Morning Mayhem starts now with David Basil,
there.
Roger Scott,
present.
And Justin
Moore. Later.
Live from the Oaklawn Racing Casino Resort Studio, Oaklawn, Arkansas's only casino resort.
Right away, I bought me a through train ticket right across Mississippi clean. I was on that midnight flyer out of Birmingham,
smoking into New Orleans.
Somebody help me get out of Louisiana, just help me get to Houston town. There are people there who care a little about me.
And they won't let the poor boy down. All right, it is 6:09. You know what time it is. Wednesday, March 27th. A little chilly out there again this morning. Get your jacket.
A little bit of frost alert. Frost alert.
Great.
Sure as you were born, they bought me a silk suit and put luggage in my hand. And I woke up high over Albuquerque
on a jet to the promised land.
Sing along.
Working on a T-bone steak.
Alicardi
flying over to the Golden State. When the pilot told us in 13 minutes
he was set us at the terminal gate.
Sweet old chariot come down, easy taxi to the terminal zone. Cut your engines and cool your wings.
And let the nigga da 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 da. Los Angeles.
You're in Norfolk, Virginia, 514-1009. Tell the folks back home, this is the promised land.
Hey, the boys on the line.
Yeah.
All right. Everybody had a great yesterday, great evening last night. We are back in studio for the last day this week. We're on the road tomorrow and Friday. Trey Reed already here this morning. Morning,
hey!
Trey.
Good morning, good morning. Well, what's up, gentlemen?
Welcome back. Missed you last week.
Well, I missed you, too. I enjoyed being away, and but good to be home.
Yes. You got a question for Trey, 661-1037. Go ahead and get the cue. Go ahead and get speaking of cue.
Cue up.
Speaking of cue. We've got some improvements to make. Los Angeles. Speaking of improvement in the queue,
yes,
when
what's the deal?
State Representative Halt comes in here, I'm going to. We have got to improve the place where you get your driver's license.
We have a new
revenue
office.
Offices. We've got to improve it.
I'm out on this conversation.
I walked in, and of course, you know, you got four people in there. You got 9,000 open windows. There's no directions. You can't see any signs.
Now, which one did you go to?
This one out in Rodney Parham.
Yeah, well, there's your first mistake.
Well,
go downtown.
Well, I've been downtown, but you know what?
North Little Rock one's never busy.
The signage has to be better. Nobody knows what's going on. Everybody's looking around. Every time I go in there, we don't know what line it was. It's just not presented very well. And you know what? Nobody cares. And those poor ladies working in there, you know, they got to deal with people getting frustrated with people walking up. It's just not really clear.
They hold the key in there.
Yeah, I know. We can be better. We can be better. We can
organize
better.
I've been railing about this for years and all that, but here's the problem. I always blame myself. First of all, I have to ask Samantha every time, all right, tell me what I'm supposed to do.
Assessment, yes.
She tells me, first thing you do, get a number.
I always get the number, which I get the number.
Yeah.
You know, but then you go, double zero, we're starting back at zero, get back up again.
David, what services were you looking to do? Well, because there's some
That's right.
that you can do online or by mail. I always renew my vehicle
Samantha
registration.
Samantha does them all online now.
You know, by mail or online, and it is so easy.
Well, the frustration thing for me, I just got a brand new driver's license 3 months ago, and it's already rubbed completely off. I got stopped by the police the other day. I give them my driver's license. They said, we can't even see this.
They're using invisible ink or what?
Wait a minute. Are you using it that often?
Look at it. And so when I went down, I had to get my daily, look at that.
Oh, my gosh.
Can you believe that is like a 3-month-old? And so the police officer.
I would caution you about showing that on the webcam. No, you can't.
The law enforcement, I had to say, I got pulled on. I said, sir, I can show you a
That's
picture.
That's not you, sir.
Yeah, and then I'm down there in Texas, you know, I had to get a daily.
For your fishing license.
And the guy goes, he said, you're going to just have to read to me. So I have a place where I have all this information that I read.
Went to get a new one of those?
Is that one of the real
it is.
IDs?
It's one of the brand new fancy stancy.
Yeah,
but apparently,
that's horrible.
Apparently, maybe it rubs it off, but it should.
No, that's
bizarre.
That's never happened.
I know.
Man.
Anyway, so I
tell you what, you know what it is? They got the lowest bidder in ink.
So all I want is just repeat. I just wanted a repeat.
A duplicate?
Yeah, duplicate. Spit it out, I'm out of there. But you know what? No. It's just, of course, I'm walking around, of course. I go in there and start talking. I said we're gonna talk about this tomorrow. Everybody,
well, you know what? There's a certain
RJ's gonna make it better.
Listen, I heard he's getting out. There's one line, certain line you go to for driver's license.
Well, that's problem. Walking around the facility, yes. Being like, I'm going to talk about that.
Yes, yes. What are we here for, ma'am? What are you here for? Well, we don't know what line. There's something.
Did you give any shirts away?
There's one line where people are in line and nobody knows. Wow, that must be a very important line because people are standing in line for that when everybody else is sitting. But you know what? You don't know what it is because the signage is not clear enough. Anyway, we can be better. Yeah, we could be better.
I got to say, my wife went to renew her license a few weeks ago, same facility,
yeah.
And she was there when the doors opened, yeah. And after they opened them, it was like, she said 19 minutes before anybody was served. If you're going to open the doors, let's start talking to customers. You know, it is right?
That's got
to
be a tough job because... Those poor people, most of them are women, are having to be deal with grumpy people, and people don't know what to do, and they go, read the directions, and, you know, we can't read the no directions.
They hold the key.
They hold the key.
Because there's officers of the law and judges right there. They're all there. Let's see what this person is. Yes, what's up? That's you. Hello.
Chuck Wagon Man, you're up.
Hey, Trey, I've got a question for you. What does the Game and Fish do with the hogs that they trap on their land?
We kill them, and then that's really the end
There's
of the
no
story.
There's no mercy. There's no mercy.
That's really the end of the story, Chuck Wagon story. Man.
There's no
Look,
mercy for
you know,
these pigs.
A lot of people say, well, why don't you donate those to, like, Hunters Feeding the Hungry? Well, we talked to Ronnie Ritter at Hunters Feeding the Hungry, and because of the potential disease issues, they don't want them, man. You know, they just don't want them.
Is there
them.
Any other animal that
Paging doesn't want them?
I don't think Ed would want to deal with those. Might cause some problems up
is that
there.
Right? Yeah, is there any other animal that we have so much
feral problems?
No. So much disinterest in saving lives of animals.
Wow,
you know, we can't kill a snake, but we'll kill 9,000 because we got a problem.
Gosh,
you know?
They're so destructive, man. They are so destructive. I tell you what, we started this conservation.
But they're so good.
hey, look, I've shot them incidental to deer hunting before, and I killed one. It's been many years ago since I've shot one, but he was a 55 pound pig. Boy, it was a pain in the butt to skin that thing, but putting that whole thing on my smoker, whoo!
Most of the time, those are okay to eat.
Yeah, I mean, they do. You just got to be really careful to cook them to a certain temperature. But they are known to carry a number of diseases, pseudorabies, brucellosis.
Pseudorabies?
Yeah.
It's not bad enough. Now there's pseudorabies.
There's not just rabies, there's pseudorabies, Roger. But man, they're so destructive. I was going to tell you, we started that conservation incentive program the first of the year, and. Basically, the legislature gave us about $3.5 million or allocated $3.5 million out of our budget that we could use for this. And the number of feral hog eradication was one of the, you know, there's lots of prescribed fire and different things. But boy, people just ate up the money. I mean, we've already allocated all of it for feral hog trapping because it went so fast. Everybody
problem.
Wants to get rid of them.
The only problem that didn't, Roger, is when we tried to go hunting to find them, they all were like, we'll show those goofballs. We're going to completely disappear.
Still unbelievable that happened.
Let me set up today's show. Of course, we'll have Trey here brought to you by Arch Marine for the next hour. Craig O'Neill coming up. If it's Wednesday, it's Craig O'Neill.
That's right.
Brought to you by Petty G Meats. RJ Hawk, brought to you by Natural State Wholesale. He'll be at 8 o'clock. We got to do Roger. We got to do a match game, and we got to do Family Feud.
Okay.
Yeah, we got to do both those games today since we missed yesterday, and it's a little bit tougher to do those on the road. It's International Whiskey Day. It's Little Red Wagon Day. Oh. Did you have a Little Red Wagon? I never had one, but I know.
It's like the third time it's been Little Red Wagon
Day. Well, it's a very popular thing in this country. Did you have one, Raj?
I did, but I think it was a hand-me-down.
Yeah, what do you call those, flyers?
Radio flyer.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's,
so you always had one of those because you had somebody that was either pulling it with a rope or you had somebody that was pushing you. You were going down
a
hill.
Cool. They were
you
cool.
You were steering it.
Steer
you
with steer that handle. Steer, yeah.
Excuse me, hold on. I said it is Little Red Wagon Day. And what did we hear? This is the third time we've had that. You know what? Maybe this great country deserves more than one Little Red Wagon Day over there, Mr. Youngster. Next we have...
Do we need to not hear from him?
Well, maybe he's more in the embracing...
Listen, he had a late night last night. working podcasts and doing things like that. Very good.
Maybe
very
he's more embracing of this. It's National.
It's a freebie.
It's National Viagra Day.
National Viagra Day.
Yeah, 26 years ago, The food FDA approved Viagra. It's hard to believe that's been 26 years and changed.
And now you go to Lion Drug. You don't need the whole thing.
I know.
Just need sildenafil.
It changed. Listen, for men with that issue, it changed.
And for men that didn't have the issue.
That's true.
Yeah. Is it prescription or is it over the counter?
It's prescription.
Yeah. Unless you know a guy.
Unless you're in Mexico.
Yeah.
It is National Quirky Country Music Song Title Day today.
Ooh, okay.
So I hadn't even dived into that to know
who
if
are those one. There's that. There's the one. What was his name? What's his name? A Wildwood Weed, I think.
Yeah,
does
those were always.
But there was one. Bubblegum on the Bedpost or something like
boy
that.
Boy Named Sue. Obviously, that's
yeah.
It.
Okay.
It's also Manatee Appreciation Day.
Big fan.
If you live in the state of Florida and not, I mean, if you've never seen a manatee, they're mammoth, and they're protected now. And you know, sometimes people are boating and they hit them and. Yeah, so they're very, I mean, you get in big trouble if you harm one of these.
You know, the late, great Jimmy Buffett was one of the greatest champions
of the
manatee conservation cause.
They look like a hippo. You know what they look like, Roger? They're a hippo and they got a big flat tail. Josh, have you ever seen one before?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're massive. I mean, they look like giant hippos, but they're very docile. They don't harm anybody for the most part, I think.
They're vegetarians.
So anyway, so that's the day. And last but not least, it's Holy Wednesday. What happened on Holy Wednesday, Raj? Do you recall?
Yes, Holy Wednesday. It's not the Last Supper.
No, that's the next day.
Yeah,
that's Thursday.
What Thursday? Is it Palm? Is it?
What'd you say?
So they were gearing up to kill Jesus.
Yeah. What? So I don't know if it's ever happened to you, but have you ever been? Betrayed.
Oh, that's it. It was a betrayal.
Yes, it was the betrayal, Judas. Yeah, that was.
Well, then where was the Last Supper?
Thursday.
So,
well, how did he betray him? I thought he betrayed him after the.
Well, I think he went to the the leaders and said, "I'll
give you my Last Supper." But then
30.
Okay, so he was setting it up.
I thought Jesus at the supper said, "One of you will betray me."
Yeah, that's right. He did.
Well, okay, hold on.
Yeah, we've got some chronological issues here.
So we had Holy Tuesday yesterday. What was the significance of that? Or do they just tack Holy on to every day this week?
They do. Yeah, they do.
Wow.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Wow.
That's,
I'm just saying.
It's every day is Holy Day. Holy Monday.
What are you Christians doing? Just tacking Holy every day? Can you not make it this week? Is it Holy Easter?
Yesterday we had Holy Tuesday, and Baz didn't explain why it was Holy Tuesday.
Well, because we should know.
It was had the Palm Sunday.
So we got to figure this out.
Yeah, you know, no, I thought we just called it
Holy Week.
It is Holy Week.
Santa Semana.
Well, then you got Maundy Thursday.
Maundy Thursday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. That's a whole different show.
I remember that guy.
Thank you.
A couple things. Last night, yesterday afternoon, Razorbacks dominate the Trojans by pitching. It was interesting to see what Chris Curry said. It said it's an embarrassment of riches how good the pitching is for Arkansas.
Unbelievable. I'm telling you, it's a murderer's row.
So you had Ben Bibee, the guy coming off mono. You ever had mono, Trey?
I never have.
We saw the Seinfeld episode with mono. Everything is about Seinfeld. Saw the Seinfeld episode with mono last night. And it was, she had to wait 6 weeks before her and George could have sex. And that was the episode where George became a genius because he stopped having sex and he started using the intellectual part of his brain. And she had mono, and that was it.
Well, we talked about yesterday. We had Peyton Stovall, who hit a home run last night, yesterday, about, you know, that used to be the kissing disease.
Yep.
And if you had it, Roger, we go, who was the girl?
Yeah.
Who'd you make out with you get mono from?
It's 2024, so we don't even ask that anymore. Who was it? It was.
I had that in high school.
Judge free.
Yeah, you had mono.
Well, it was like you started off the day fine, much like he described, and then you just get exhausted for no reason. Like, they allowed me to check out of school whenever I wanted to. It was great. School.
And it lasts like.
How old were you?
Like weeks.
No,
said a couple, 3 weeks.
3 weeks. Yeah.
Like, no, they told me like 2 months. Like, they were all about.
The thing that Peyton Stovall mentioned about Ben Bibee, the guy who pitched yesterday, he said he didn't lose any weight and he was able to come back. Yeah. So it was Ben Bibee. Bobby, Dylan Carter, you know Dylan, Randy's grandson, Kristen Fauch and Stone Hewlett, I think, all combined for a two-hit shutout. I mean, this pitching staff is unbelievable. He says Arkansas has just an embarrassment of riches for arms. That was Chris Curry. He says that's where it starts to impeach. Listen to this, 71% of their pitches yesterday were strikes.
Wow.
71%?
I was about to almost say, like, if you're a hitter, if you know that, You see that would enhance your get up there, swing, and make contact.
Start swinging, man.
Yeah. By the way, Clint told me we should all download the Easter Now app On Tuesday, Jesus returned to the temple to teach and preach.
Oh, that's when he got mad.
Along the way, the disciples noticed the fig tree withered from
the
roots.
Fig tree parable. That's right.
And then today it says, tomorrow at twilight begins a historical slaughter of the lambs at twilight, which kicks off Passover. So I guess there's really not any significance to today. It's just kind of a preparation day for us Christians.
Well, when I saw it, it was saying that this was the beginning of the...
We should know this.
Yes. Well, again, Tommy used to be really strong because he's Catholic. Catholic
pigskin preacher, if you're listening. And Broadway. Joe Klein.
So the Razorbacks win. I guess it was a 10-run rule because they finished the game in the seventh inning. They canceled the softball game or postponed it. So I thought it was interesting. So they allowed the guys to play. But apparently the ladies felt it was too cold to play yesterday. Look, maybe softball is different from baseball. I don't know.
It was the temperature why they moved the game up.
Yes.
And I was thrilled because it allowed the wild side to be on at its normal time at 7 o'clock last night rather than tonight. It makes for a very long day for me.
But they called that game, and I was at Sauced, bar none. I got a chance to see all the gang out there, Kevin Case.
Thanks, Kevin.
I was actually, I'm like you, I was glad I was able to watch the game at 3 o'clock. But that was interesting. The women called it. And just postponed it that early, and the men played it. So
you're saying that you think that they would look adorable if they had little sweaters on?
I don't know.
While they were playing?
I don't know. But
I wonder if it's the top button. He's baiting you, David. Stop it.
I wonder if their bats are different, where maybe they can't hit.
I wonder, is that ball any different? Is it made any different than the baseball?
That's a good.
I don't know. I'm trying to figure out a Holy Wednesday.
While Roger was doing trivia last night, Arkansas State was down by 12.
Yes.
They come back.
With a shot.
With a chance to win at the end. Missed a shot.
You can't ask for anything better. Unless you make it. That was it. Yeah.
So Arkansas State ends the season 20-17. Their season is done. But that was a good game last night. The other thing, too, I wanted to mention, there was a winner last night in the Mega Million. Did you hear that?
Yes.
So somebody in New Jersey, I think it was New Jersey, won $1.13 billion. Mm. So your choice is, I think I saw it somewhere, you either get $500 million lump sum or you get it paid out. And I just wonder what the payout would be, how long it takes. We'll see if we can find it.
How much is the payout?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's $1.13 billion.
Yeah, but how much? They're not giving you all that
money. No, they didn't.
I mean, how much is it
monthly?
Well,
you can for $500 million.
Yeah, I'm asking, but if you don't do that.
I don't know. That's what I'm saying. I don't know.
Somebody's got to find it. We got to know what it is because here's the thing. I think we've talked about it before. If something were to happen to me, if I'm the ticket holder, do they continue to make those payments to my family and or heirs?
Yeah, I would think so.
I don't know.
Arkansas Lottery, Brian Morse was saying that this at $1.1 million, and so they said your odds are a lot better because that's just Arkansas that get And I forget what, I think he said the odds of winning that 1.3, whatever, the billion is 300 million to one. So, I mean, it's almost like, you know, because he bought five tickets. He said, buy one. I said, I didn't buy one because I know the odds are so astronomical. I feel like it's just a complete waste of money. But you can't win. Listen, he's a guy that's won $1 million.
Yeah.
So, you know, he can speak from experience.
He's won multiple times.
He's won. That's exactly right. So, anyway, so that was last night. Also, did you see where they found that looks like the body count from the bridge yesterday is 6? Apparently, they came back and said no cars were on. They were actually. So
I've looked at that tape extensively and waiting on that, waiting to see the last car go by before the bridge collapsed, before the barge hit it. What a wonderful, wonderful mechanism that they have, that when they put out that Mayday, so that was crucial because then that Mayday goes out and they shut down that bridge and they don't allow it. So I don't know where that is here. And of course they've said our waterways and navigable waters
are on top of the bridge.
So I've been on that bridge.
I'm assuming it's just like I don't know if they have a drawbridge or so, huh?
They shut down, but there's like a little toll thing.
It goes down
on each side where they can.
Well, is somebody there physically?
Well, I don't know if anybody's there physically. Somebody could be somewhere at a remote place.
If you shut it down immediately, something has to either
get out of the remote. They put out a Mayday, and a Mayday happens.
I know,
that
but you have to have something that stops.
Ideally, hopefully you got something that goes down. Because
that's what I'm saying.
If you don't, then people are still going to try to beat it like you do a train. But what a wonderful thing that was. So, they have called off any of the searches.
Six of the workers were working on, potholes on that
day. Construction crew. Yeah.
And then did you see they've got video of where they've sort of sped up the video just to show the how that thing came around them. Yeah. And did they say what happened? The guy just lost
power.
Yeah, NTSB will get on there today. They waited, and they're going to wait till today, but they'll get a couple dozen people.
You're out there working all night on a road, potholes on a bridge, and you look up. Maybe you don't even look up. You're going... oh my gosh, they're going to hit us. And then you think, well, maybe it won't collapse, the whole thing, and then you're falling 170 feet in cold water in the middle of the dark.
If you were crossing that bridge, you know it because it just happened. So you know if you were crossing that bridge, you can go back and look at how close to death you were. Or close to being seriously injured. Not to say that you would automatically die, but I mean, when you see those vehicles go by and you see them humming across that bridge.
That bridge is high, it is tight, and it's scary. When we go across that bridge, it is not a fun one. Yeah. You cannot wait.
It's not when it's
the Francis Scott Key Bridge, right?
Yeah, they don't say our bridge is that was a bigger barge than that goes through our.
It was a massive.
It was a massive cargo.
It was
3 football fields long and 1.5 wide.
We don't have any of that, and they're not built to withstand a shot like that from the side.
Yeah, it's a really disturbing thing to see, that. Couple other things. If you got a question for Trey, 661-1037. We'll check our Southern Structural Solution text line here in just a minute. Did you hear about the new rules for NFL kickoff?
Mm-hmm.
Have you heard of Trey? It's interesting.
Yeah, but I'm not sure I completely understand.
We'll try to break it down for you. I get it. It completely changes what a kickoff is, what we know it. And of course, they've been doing it in the XFL apparently already.
Yeah.
And so, are they doing this just for the NFL? But is the college talking about it too, or no? Just NFL? Hadn't heard.
The NFL's going to do it. I don't think college has made the jump yet.
It's interesting. The kickoff as we know it. I can say, Roger, I played in the era where I was a wedge buster. And I would have concussions every time I go down there. But it was fun. Going in there, bust that wall up, baby. Bust that wall. Throw your
butt. Guy.
Just give up your body for the
calls.
Throw
it out there.
And now, look, kids are making more money. I didn't make a dime for that. I can't walk.
Boy, and speaking of kids that are making more money, Johnny Daly's quote yesterday has gotten some big traction.
It is. John basically said, these kids that are snapping to quarterbacks that are making millions and all these linemen are getting are –
a barbecue ain't gonna cut it.
Yeah, a plate of barbecue, and so that sort of pick. Which there's some truth that maybe obviously a little exaggerated. Well, last year probably was a good case of that. Probably about the truth. All right, 6:30 here, Morning Mayhem.
Mark your calendars for the 20th annual Double B's BuzzBecue, Saturday, May 11th at the downtown Riverside RV Park in North Little Rock. Tickets on sale soon.
This is SportsCenter.
Arkansas Razorbacks baseball cruised to an 11-0 win yesterday over in-state rival Little Rock. Ben Bibee, Dylan Carter, Christian Fouch, and Stone Hewitt combined to throw his 7 innings of shutout baseball. Bibee struck out 5 of the 10 batters that he faced. And on the day, Vahiva Aloy, the shortstop for the Hogs, drove in 4 runs as well. The Hogs are now 20-3 overall. They host number 8 LSU this weekend in a Thursday, Friday, Saturday series. First game is 6 p.m. on Thursday. Second game is 7 o'clock. On Friday, the series finale is at 2 p.m. on Saturday afternoon. Arkansas softball had their game against UCA canceled due to cold temperatures. I'm Josh Neighbors for the Buzz Radio Network.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Another sunny but cool day with a high of just 62 degrees. Not as windy as yesterday, though, and tonight's low will drop back down to about 39. A little warmer tomorrow at 68 and low 70s back by Friday. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Tito's Handmade Vodka presents the 2024 1037 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course. Registration is now open. Go to 1037thebuzz.com to register your 4-person team. Prizes will be awarded in both the morning and afternoon flights. The 2024 1037 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course. Presented by Tito's Handmade Vodka and brought to you in part by Lion Legal, with special thanks to Corky's Ribs and Barbecue, Sonic, and Michelob Ultra.
You've heard about the thousands of patients finally getting relief from chronic joint pain thanks to QC Kinetics non-invasive treatments. And here's one who was determined to avoid surgery. Meet Vicky.
The orthopedic surgeon said, well, you're going to need knee replacement sooner rather than later. I kept hearing commercials about QC Kinetics and thought, well, I'm going to check them out first.
QC Kinetics has treated over 20,000 patients like Vicky around the country. People who were told they needed surgery but chose a more natural, less invasive approach that uses regenerative treatments to help heal and restore painful joints with no downtime.
If QC Kinetics had not been what I expected, I would have gone through with the surgery, but I got so much relief, am now pretty much pain-free that I don't have to have the surgery.
Before going under the knife, you need to check out QC Kinetics. The consultation is free. Call today.
Call QC Kinetics, 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440.
Spring has sprung, and that spells fun. Fun is in Arch Marine in North Little Rock. Arch has new 2024 G3 Tritunes. That's right, I said Tritunes in stock. And as always, don't forget Arch Marine is your John Boat headquarters. They're powered by Tohatsu and Yamaha outboards. Arch also has an excellent selection of the ever-so-popular G3 boats, models 22, 23, and 2024. Make your summer one to remember by stopping by Arch Marine in North Little Rock. Take the Levy exit.
The all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock is now open. Over 100,000 square feet of hardware, outdoor appliances, a window and door center, and even a drive-through lumber yard. And there's nothing like Design One. This stunning showroom is one place for all your home and design needs, including 12 full kitchens and 9 baths, plus a huge selection of lighting, flooring, countertops, and more. At the all-new Lumber One and Design One, now open in West Little Rock.
Always make sure to say please and thank you. Morning Mayhem is back on the air, live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios, Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
What's that bulge in his pocket?
It's Trey Reed from the Arkansas Game and Fish Commission. If you've got questions about outdoor life in Arkansas, Trey is the guy with all the answers. Brought to you by Arts Marine. Arts Marine in North Little Rock has been carrying Yamaha, G3, and Tohatsu for over 50 years. Call them today at 753-7351.
I love the sound of the fish in the water there in that open. Somebody says, fix your camera, Baz. It's driving my wife crazy.
Yeah,
Roger, that tells me that
is.
People are watching.
Yes, thank you.
Josh. Listen, I get in trouble. You got to help me out
here,
man. You got to help me out.
What are you thinking?
Come on, look. I got to look here.
You're better than that.
Come on, Josh.
Come on, Ike. You're better than that.
I did take a fishing trip down. You'd heard about this, Trey.
Yeah, I heard you talking about it in
Lake Fork.
Here's my question, David. I heard you say you drove 4 hours down and 4 hours back to fish for 2 hours?
Yes. We got there. It's so funny. The guy who's in Arkansas, his name is Rick Carter. He's the guy down there. Okay. Great guy. Been there 40 years. We get down there. We're getting ready to go out. We're supposed to get down there at 12. And he goes, I've got to finish up a few hours with this other group.
Oh,
a few hours.
Yes.
He used the term, I got to finish up a few hours.
Yeah.
Oh,
so we didn't get out until 4. We fished from 4 to 6.
I passed Sarge on the way back.
It was a good time.
Yeah. Yeah. And, you know, what's crazy is the kid that he had a group from California he was guiding that morning. Kid never bass fished before in his life. First fish was a 1-pounder. Second, 11 pounds,
wow.
3 ounces.
Well,
11
pounds. You caught some fish, but not
the
big. I caught
one. You know how I caught him? I caught him up underneath his mouth. I didn't even catch him in the mouth. I somehow.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
But can I tell you, I meant to bring this up yesterday, Roger. You know what's embarrassing as a man?
Well, I do.
When you fishing?
Oh, I've had something else.
So, because when you don't, there's two types of rod. There's two types of reels.
Okay.
You have a bait casting, mm-hmm. and you have a spinning reel. Mm-hmm. Spinning is a little bit more easy. You just open the little guide and throw it. Mm-hmm. Bait casting is your thumbs on top of it.
Okay.
And when you don't bait cast much.
Does it almost fly?
No, it's not like fly, but if you don't bait cast much, it's very easy to
get a backlash.
The thing is tangled.
Oh.
And so every time it would do that with me, I'd have to hand it Rick. Give it to me. Sure, Rick, we're going to give it in. He would have to had to put it back. It was so embarrassing because, and then after a while, I got better at it.
So why you didn't take your? I mean, I know you purchased a bait casting reel before your tournament. What last year? Year before?
Yes.
That would It had a, you know, it would prevent those professional overruns, as we call them.
Well, I asked, and they go, don't bring anything. They go, they should let us that way. That's what they requested.
But it's
embarrassing. I feel like I'm 3 years old. Here's my spool all messed up. Can you get it untangled? It's so embarrassing.
Oh my god.
I feel like going. Let me get my own. Let me get my thing untangled myself. I'm not going to tell you from now on. I'm just going to. He told me with a zit zit zit. Anyway, I do have to. Plus, the other thing, the white caps on the lake.
Yeah, we were
blowing 40 miles an hour. I was like, man, this is
not
good.
How do you set that up?
You know, this is. I mean, I love my job and I love all the hunting and fishing I get to do.
Nobody's denying that.
I mean. You think about these professional anglers that are going out. They don't get to, you know, we can decide. Like, we can look at the forecast.
Right.
You know, most folks are like, I'm going to stay home today. It's only, you know, the wind's blowing 25. But, you know, if you're a guide or you're a professional angler you're filming, you know, opportunities for Arkansans like we do. You don't get that. You don't have that leisure. You're just there, man.
You got to
deal with it.
We went to the coves. Where there was no wind. I wanted to ask you as a comparison to Arkansas, so I had to buy a one-day deal, and I was going to say, I forgot, what is a one-day deal in Arkansas?
I don't even know, David, because I mean, I live here, and I buy mine for $10.50 for the whole year.
That was my next question. What is it for the year?
$10.50 for a resident fishing license.
You know what it was for me to get one for a year in Texas? Now, I don't know if this was because I'm a non-resident or not.
I'm sure it was.
What's a non-resident in Arkansas?
I'll look it up.
It was $60 for the year if I was to get that for the rest of the year.
That just keeps getting better, don't it?
Wow. I didn't buy that. He goes, you're going to come back? He says, because you could buy the whole one. I said, why don't we just go ahead and stick with the one day? And we'll see. And if I get lucky, I might come back and buy a full one. anyway.
Oh, my God. So the full year would have been cheaper than the one day?
No. The one day was $14, but the full day was $60. Oh. I was just saying.
Wait a minute. Well, you just said the one day and the full day. Say it again.
One day is $14.
Okay.
And for the year is $60.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I was going to see how.
I'm looking it up David. Yeah, we'll find it.
But listen, Roger, as I said, Trey, to Roger, it was fun being part of the crew, the fishing crew. These guys all do it for a living.
Yeah.
And that lake has become well-known, Trey. I don't know if you know this, for producing really big fish.
Oh, absolutely. Lake Fork's, I mean, it's been famous for years.
It's not that far away either.
Back in the 80s, my stepdad, you know, who was big into bass fishing at the time, would, you know, he would always like, I want to take that dream trip to Lake Fork.
What is the lake in Arkansas that you could go? Okay, the biggest bass is Dardanelle, or is it in that area where?
Dardanelle's good, but the Arkansas River down around what they call the Dumas Pool, but around Pendleton, the lower part of the Arkansas River before it hits the White and the Mississippi. And not the river channel itself, but the backwaters. That's kind of probably one of the most well-known big bass places. Although Lake Millwood, I was actually down on
Lake Millwood. I've
Millwood,
heard that.
Yeah, Millwood Lake.
Texarkana?
Hope, Ashdown area. Okay. Yeah, you can find some big ones down there. Generally, the farther south you go, typically the bigger the fish are going to be.
But you know what's crazy, Roger, is that, and I know Trey knows this, is that even today, when you catch an 11-pounder, you know what they do? They put it back. Back in the old days, oftentimes you were going to mount that sucker.
Yeah.
But down there, and maybe even here, what they do is really, I found this out, that they measure it, take a picture of it, and that's what the what do you call
you
it?
You make a replica.
They basically, they,
oh, really?
They create
yeah.
something.
That's cool. Isn't yeah. it? Or is well, that is no, that good
I,
or bad?
I think it's good. Is there any negative
for that?
I don't think so. I mean.
It basically shows this is the fish I caught.
And there's a lot of people, like Harper's Pure Country Taxidermy in Damascus, who's worked with us on the wild side before, they do those. Dwayne Hayda, who's a fantastic artist, he does trout replicas like that. Of course, the catch and release ethic is kind of always, it kind of came from the trout fishing side, you know, the fly fishing, and then when the tournament started, when bass tournaments started in the late 60s, actually one of the first big ones was on Beaver Lake in 67 or 68. And you know, they kept their catch.
I know,
you know, they kept
then.
It, and that then big you know, it started like a you know, the optics of that weren't great. And so Ray Scott, the founder of BASS, like, hey, we, you know, encourage the boat manufacturers to start including a live well with aerators to keep the catch alive so you could release it.
And let me tell you the other reason I think, Roger, too, why it's not a big deal to release it, because back then, most of us didn't have cameras in our boats.
Yeah.
Now you get to take the picture, and the picture's almost enough to where everybody just get the picture,
yeah.
So you well, sure here, you caught it.
Here,
you
know, here, I'll give you another reason that, that I prefer the replica mounts. They're made out of fiberglass, and they last forever, whereas that skin mount where you actually, you know, peel the skin off of the fish and then form it around, it deteriorates. I mean, for example, we've got a mount, the original mount, a skin mount of the state record largemouth bass. It's in one of my colleague's office 16? At Game and Fish.
16?
Yeah, 16-4, I think. Anyway, it's all ratty, man. It's like it's coming apart, man.
Can they make
like
a replica of that now?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, we've got replicas of the in our office and some of the nature centers of the one that was caught over at
illegally?
Village Creek State Park.
Gotcha. Yeah, okay.
Illegally.
So that's what that is.
Lake
Dunn.
A couple of messages on our text line. Lake Columbia is a big bass lake.
That's another good one.
Lake Darnell has strip pits where big bass live.
Yep.
Strip pits, Roger. You know about the strip pits?
I think Jeff Allen goes to those when he gets off.
What was the biggest bass Trey has seen on Millwood?
There was like an 11 or 12 caught earlier this year, but I don't know what the biggest, I don't know what the lake
record is. So it says Lake Atkins?
Atkins is another good one, although it's kind of on the downhill. You know, we renovated it about 25 years ago, and it was just amazing for about a 10-year period there. Monticello was another good one that'll be coming back online. You know, it's been drained and been renovated.
Well, can I tell you, I caught as many giant bass in Arkansas as I did in Texas that
Bingo.
One day.
Hey, hit that bell, Roger. Come on, ring the bell.
So Texas didn't represent Arkansas just as good on that day. Someone said, hey, Baz, two words for you. Zip code 33. Or, yeah, listen, remember the old zip code? There wasn't any backlash on that sucker. That's you know, every they still make those.
Oh, absolutely. You know what ZEPCO is an acronym for?
I think years ago, right? This could be a trivia question.
It would be a great trivia
question.
King
of all trivia.
ZEPCO.
We know
it's a company. We know it's a company, right?
It is rooted in the oil and gas exploration industry in Oklahoma.
Wow. Z, what would the Z stand for?
Zephyr.
Zephyr.
This is a tease. We'll talk about it after the break.
Tell you what, well, Texas, if you will, 661-1037. Let's see if they know. We'll be back in just a minute.
Nothing compares to the feeling of wearing a Facets of Fire diamond from Sissy's Log Cabin. The first diamond cutting advancement in over a century, Facets of Fire diamonds are created by etching thousands of nanoprisms onto the pavilion of an exquisite natural diamond. The result is a stone with more brilliance than any other. Just ask any of the expert staff at Sissy's and they'll show you the vibrant burst of fiery color that's visible to the naked eye. From engagement rings to necklaces to bracelets to earrings, a Facets of Fire diamond takes any piece to a new level of spectacular, and no jewelry collection is complete without one. Facets of Fire diamonds are passion personified, but don't just take my word for it. You can shop Facets of Fire online at sissyslogcabin.com or at any of their 6 locations. Experience the revolution in diamonds for yourself only at Sissy's Log Cabin, because life's too short for ordinary jewelry.
Now's the time to get a great deal on a Kubota Z200 Series mower with the new K-Ride Comfort System. The Series delivers a quality cut and an exceptional ride. Right now, get a Kubota Z200 Series mower with K-Ride Comfort System for 0% down, 0% APR for 48 months, now through March 31st. See us or go to KubotaUSA.com for full disclaimer. Hennard Foothills Equipment, South Main Street in Searcy, your hometown Kubota dealer no matter where you live. 501-268-1987.
John Mellencamp, live and in person 2024.
Well, I was born in a small town. I live in a small town.
One night only.
All but 8,000 America.
April 10th at Robinson Center.
I swear the sport was a sport.
Tickets on sale now at Mellencamp.com.
Hello,
folks. It's Frank Fletcher from the Fletcher Dodge store here in Sherwood. For the past few months, we've been asking you to give us a chance to buy your cars, and the response has been great. We really appreciate all of you who brought your cars in and turned it into cash. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Folks, we're still buying cars every day. So look around and see what you or your family has in the garage that you want to turn into cash. It's really easy, folks. Just come into Fletcher Dodge and ask for Chris or Andy. We'll buy any vehicle and we'll pay you more than anyone. We can't find enough vehicles at the auto auctions to meet the demand, so we're extending you this offer to the public. We'll pay you more, so don't wait. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Come see us today for the best cash offer on your car, truck, van, or SUV. Just ask for Chris or Andy. We'll pay you more, so come see us at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood. Thanks.
Red tape. One in three businesses will get caught up in it, and they'll be penalized by the IRS for mismanaging their payroll. Because when you're handling payroll, HR compliance, and those constantly changing tax laws, that red tape can get sticky in a hurry. At The Payroll Company, we free you from that tangled mess and get you back to business. The Payroll Company. Less headaches, more than payroll. Visit morethanpayroll.com to learn more.
It's the Ranger Open House Sale through Monday at Bradford Marine and ATV at all six statewide locations. Blast to the boat show deals like the Ranger 520R with 250 horsepower Mercury with trailer and up to a $2,000 Bass Pro gift card and discounts up to $10,000 on select models. Or check out the SunTracker Sportfish 22, great for fishing and cruising with 115 horsepower Mercury outboard. Don't miss the Open House Sale today through April 1st at all Bradford Marine and ATV statewide locations. Your authorized Ranger and Tracker dealer.
Roger Scott here. Let me remind you about my friends at Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union. They have some of the most aggressive auto loan rates for Buzz listeners in Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry counties. Easy access to Alcoa's team of loan officers online, by phone or in person at Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union's two locations in Benton and Sheridan, and apply online at alcoacommunityfcu.org.
Your morning drive will never be the same with Morning Mayhem on the radio, live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios. Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
What's his name? Josh?
Josh Neighbors.
Comment about Waterboy not being worth anything?
Yes. Yeah.
These millenniums ain't got no taste in movies.
You ain't got no taste.
These millenniums.
There ain't been a good movie made in the last 10 years.
Yes, these millenniums have no taste.
You ain't got no good taste.
Hey, you millennium.
Oh, my gosh, so good. All right, we got Trey Reed for a few more minutes. Great to have him back in the studio, brought to you by Arch Marine. All right, so I'm going to run through these real quick. These are our messages on our Southern Structural Solutions text line. My first EPCO was a 202. I think they might have started with 33, but 202.
Yeah, the 202 was another one, yep.
Zero. Okay, what is it?
Zero Hour Bomb Company.
My buddy Gerald Jones got that right. So I've never heard of that.
Yeah, so it originated Zepco. From some piece of machinery or equipment that they used in the oil exploration industry and figure out how to retrofit that into a reel, I think, is sort of the short version of the story.
Had no, Roger, that could be a really challenging King of All Trivia question.
Actually, he's already made notes.
Lake Greenlee and Brinkley is a big bass hammer spot.
Yeah,
true.
Yeah.
White Oak Lake is a good one for big bass.
Oh, White Oak Lake is a good one, yeah.
I'm headed there crappie fishing this week. They were doing that down there. Listen, I tell you, the everybody loves fishing for crappie because it tastes so good.
You mentioned Atkins. SWEPCO up in northwest Arkansas near Gentry is another one. It's a power plant lake. It's got a warm water discharge, and so it can sustain Florida bass, which are stocked in that.
Let's go to Stan. Stan, you got a question for Trey.
Yeah, good morning, guys.
Morning.
Hey, can y'all hear me?
Yeah, we can.
We got you, Stan.
Yeah, good morning. Hey, Trey, look here. You know all my people live. I got a bunch of people live down in Nashville. You know Nashville, Arkansas. Yeah, I go down there.
I remember you telling me that.
And I keep catching them damn spoonfish.
paddlefish.
No, with a spoon bill. Hey, man, is that the only place that spoonfish are located?
In
Millwood, man?
They're in a lot of our rivers.
What are they called?
It's a paddlefish.
Yeah. Are they edible?
They are. Okay. They are. Probably they're... The caviar, the roe from them is what's most valuable, and there's a commercial industry on that. The Arkansas River is a big paddlefish fishery. Beaver Lake, our Game and Fish stocked them in Beaver Lake to kind of have a if that commercial harvest for the caviar had crashed the population. We stocked them in beaver to have sort of a backup source that we could replenish other bodies of water with. It was a world record paddlefish.
Oh, wow.
By spearfish.
They get big. They get big.
Caught like last summer or the summer before. Like, the real big. Matter of fact, I believe a lake up in Missouri just in the last week or two, somebody caught one like 164
pounds. They're massive. Almost
world,
like it looked like an alligator gar kind of deal. It's 6:52. If it's Wednesday on Morning Mayhem, Craig O'Neill is going to be here. He's coming up shortly after Trey. Yeah. Here's one that says, hey, Baz, hey, Roger, got an adventure for you guys. How about a catch and release turkey hunting event? Now, what in the world? Well,
I don't know how we do that.
When do we do the turkey hunt?
Turkey season opens for everybody April 15th, and the youth hunt is the weekend prior to that. So what would that be? I'm trying to think of my days now. It's the Saturday and Sunday, 8 days before it opens on the 15th.
Are we going fishing again?
I think we could do it all, my friend. We could do it all.
We're going to have a spring and summer adventure.
You don't catch and release turkey, though. That's a joke, right?
No, yeah, it's got to be a joke.
That's a joke. Yeah,
I would think so.
And the white turkey, the guy that had the white turkey, he said Trey only gets them if they're raised that way. We got to do the fishing. I want to get a fishing.
Yeah, we will.
I got a little hooked up. Come on, Daddy.
Yeah, the other thing, too, I was just thinking, I'm going to get my deer head back, and I was thinking, should I have done the deer head and tail? Because it just, you know, the body, just the head just doesn't fit.
You don't have enough room for that. The head's fine. I don't want you
I'm
tail.
Just going with the head, Dave.
Go with the head. Go with the head.
That was sort of a joke.
Do they? Oh, was it really?
Yes.
I don't know if it was or not. Do they do the fiberglass deer?
No.
Someone says Texas has a share lunker program where they take the big ones and breed them. Is that something Arkansas does?
Not yet,
okay.
But newsflash, that's coming.
Interesting.
We have actually been talking about that and how we're going to execute that plan for some time. But that is something that Arkansas will be doing and announcing very soon.
Very nice. I will say, Roger, listening to these guys, you listen to your show or Sarge's on the weekend.
Right.
To hear people name these lures they have, like when I was in there fishing, and it's almost like a John Gruden play call in the NFL.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, it's like, it's
and the colors. We had a guy on the wild side last night who's made a film about the Little Red River, and he had previously made a documentary film about the wine industry in Georgia, and he was talking about Scuppernong.
Scuppernong!
And Hedrick's like, well, that's one of the best lure colors of all time.
Oh, wow, that is so great.
It was a drop shot that was going, I can't even repeat it. It was like four words. Like, what'd you just say? It's just a combo. Like, I remember for mine, Roger, it was a snagless Sally with a pork rind.
Yes,
that's what I used to get.
We could have a ball one day just like going through the names of lures. I'll have to do like some Shannon Lynn type prep where we could have fun doing this segment talking about the crazy lure names.
Someone says here, I'm not a big fisherman. What happened to eating the fish, forget mounting or releasing? Well, I think it depends on the fish. Bass are not really a fish that I think people are excited about eating.
The smaller ones are pretty good. I mean,
but you'd rather eat a crappie before you have to eat. It's not even close.
All day long. A lot of people don't realize the world record bass that was caught in, I believe, 1932 in Georgia. The reason there's a lot of controversy surrounding it because like there's one known photo, but
22
it was
pounds.
Middle of the Depression. Yeah. Guess what happened to the world record bass? They ate it.
Yeah, just think
pounds of bass will feed a family for a couple of days.
Wow. Yeah, just think of that 20 something pounds.
Yeah.
So, you got turkey season coming up. Anything else we need to know from getting
fish? Man, it's a good time to go fishing. And, we were joking about the prices and what you paid for your license. But, man, $10.50, you can fish as a resident all year long in Arkansas. What a hell of a bargain.
What did you say the date was? The beginning date of turkey?
April 15th.
Somebody says, but hey, Bass, if you're part of a DMAC program, you can hunt turkey April 1st.
No, David, don't take the bait, man.
tongue in cheek there. 661-1037.
It's called TMAP, David.
What about Lakes Hot Springs Village? Somebody was asking here about the lakes and Hot Springs Village.
And it's like I was focusing on, public bodies of water, game and fish lakes, or other public, regulatory authorities, but there are so many like little farm ponds, and you went with Gerald Jones who answered our Zero Hour Bomb Company question on an irrigation reservoir, and they're private, but if you can get in on one of those, man, they are a great place to catch big bass. But they're you know, I mean, some of the best fishing is are in those off the beaten path, off the wall places, and so there's a lot of great places to fish in Arkansas.
Casper in Valonia makes a great point here. Guys, this is a historic moment for Morning Mayhem Radio, and the Buzz, for that matter, because Stan just called in and did not mention either a dual-threat quarterback or Nolan Richardson in a national championship.
He's absolutely right.
A lot of people don't know, Stan is pretty avid when it comes to fishing. Stan likes to talk fishing.
And of course, you can get a double dose of Trey on Tuesday nights.
Tuesday nights at 7, the Wild Side, you know. But we're going to be bouncing around with baseball season, those midweek games. We'll probably be on Wednesdays and Thursdays quite a bit over the next couple of months.
If folks want to find you, if they got questions, if they want you to come make an appearance, how do they get
Look, you can go to agfc.com and click on the media section, and my contact information, email, and phone number are there. You can always hit me up on Instagram at @3REID.
Awesome. Thanks, Trey. Great.
Thank you, guys.
Great.
Have a great Wednesday.
All right. The legend, Craig O'Neill, is up next.
ESPN and The Buzz gives you the complete sports and entertainment package.
I love that game.
103.7 The Buzz, KABZ Little Rock.
It's Derby time at Oaklawn, and I'm going to be there. The Arkansas Derby is this Saturday, March 30th. 13 race card, first post time, 12 o'clock noon. Doors open at 10:30. Of course, you got the 1.5 million Arkansas Derby, 200 Kentucky Derby qualifying points. You've also got the 750,000 fantasy stakes and the 500,000 Oaklawn mile. Also, a special Derby Day dawn at Oaklawn, 7:30 to 9:30 on the South Track apron and free barn tours. Don't forget, there's also racing on Thursday and Friday. Thursday, March 28th, discount days, free parking, free program, and $1 hot dogs. And you've got the Temperance Hill Stakes on Friday, March 29th. It's also March Madness in full swing. Oaklawn is ready to help you make money with their Oaklawn Sports app, where new customers can earn $1,000 in bonus bets. You heard me right, $1,000. All you have to do, download the Oaklawn Sports app from Apple or Google Play. Oaklawn Sports is giving you this opportunity for your first 10 days, starting on the day of your initial deposit. Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
A lot of talk.
Why do you have to talk like that?
And a lot more attitude.
You have a problem, turn off your station.
103.7 The Buzz, KABZ Little Rock. Buzz News with Channel 7's Cassandra Webb.
Little Rock Mayor Frank Scott Jr. is among 21 mayors who will travel to Memphis today, joining the Black Mayors Coalition on Crime and its efforts to reduce violent crime in America's cities. Memphis Mayor Paul Young launched the effort in partnership with the African American Mayors Association. Young took office in Memphis earlier this year and says a high-profile national movement of mayors could help solve ongoing issues with crime. According to a recent Gallup poll, voters' concerns about crime are at their highest level since 2016. Local businesses are stocking their shelves ahead of the total solar eclipse. Edwards Food Giant is preparing for an increased volume of customers looking to buy meat, bread, and other staple items for the eclipse. They plan on getting some trucks ahead of time with all those groceries. Cavanaugh Pharmacy is also getting necessities in case of an emergency. They'll have Band-Aids, Neosporin, antiseptic, and all other health items. Both stores will carry NASA-approved solar eclipse glasses while supplies last. From the Channel 7 Newsroom, I'm Cassandra Webb.
Brought to you by Floyd Seafood, Keel Avenue in Sherwood. It's crawfish season, and Floyd's has live Louisiana crawfish. Order by 1 p.m. Thursday for weekend boils. Floyd's Meat and Seafood.com.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Another sunny but cool day with a high of just 62 degrees. Not as windy as yesterday, though, and tonight's low will drop back down to about 39. A little warmer tomorrow at 68 and low 70s back by Friday. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Tune in each week to Out of Bounds to hear from team captain Kendall Diggs. Omaha is the goal, and we're looking for a great season. Kendall Diggs is brought to you by Stephen Elmore with Shelter Insurance. For auto, home, life, or business insurance, see shelter agent Stephen Elmore or give him a call at 501-537-0959.
Roger Scott for the Carpet Barn. The question was asked of me, does the Carpet Barn have other flooring? I responded, well, of course they do. They have a wide selection of hardwood, tile, stone, vinyl, and luxury vinyl plank, or LVP, if you will. But think about it. The name would have to be the Carpet, Hardwood, Laminate, Tile, Stone, Luxury Vinyl Barn that does backsplashes and custom showers. And that's too long. You see why the name is The Carpet Barn, your flooring specialist since 1968. The Carpet Barn will complete the process from the complimentary measures and stay with you every step of the way from selection to installation. Flooring for today and beyond. The Carpet Barn, with locations in North Little Rock on Maumelle Boulevard and in Conway on Oak Street. Both Carpet Barn stores open on Saturday by appointment. The Carpet Barn, flooring specialist since 1968. Check them out and get a head start by doing that at thecarpetbarn.net.
This Saturday, one lucky Saracen casino player will win a Corvette Stingray from Guatney Chevrolet. This new Corvette is the pinnacle of precision, and with 500 horses and 0 to 60 in under 3 seconds, you'll have more speed than you'll ever need. You can win the most powerful production Stingray in history just for playing, but only at the Saracen Casino Resort, and only this Saturday.
Saracen Casino Resort, Vegas, Arkansas style.
Gambling problem? Call 800-522-4700.
The all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock is now open. Over 100,000 square feet of hardware, outdoor appliances, a window and door center, and even a drive-through lumber yard. And there's nothing like Design One. This stunning showroom is one place for all your home and design needs, including 12 full kitchens and 9 baths, plus a huge selection of lighting, flooring, countertops, and more at the all-new Lumber One and Design One, now open in West Little Rock.
You've heard about the thousands of patients finally getting relief from chronic joint pain thanks to QC Kinetics non-invasive treatments. And here's one who was determined to avoid surgery. Meet Vicky.
The orthopedic surgeon said, well, you're going to need knee replacement sooner rather than later. I kept hearing commercials about QC Kinetics and thought, well, I'm going to check them out first.
QC Kinetics has treated over 20,000 patients like Vicky around the country. People who were told they needed surgery but chose a more natural, less invasive approach that uses regenerative treatments to help heal and restore painful joints with no downtime.
If QC Kinetics had not been what I expected, I would have gone through with the surgery, but I got so much relief, am now pretty much pain-free that I don't have to have the surgery.
Before going under the knife, you need to check out QC Kinetics. The consultation is free. Call today.
Call QC Kinetics, 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440.
Mark Normand. You don't say, Tor.
Hate the small talk. Two things I can't do, small talk and eye contact. How sad is that, you know? I basically have all the traits of a serial killer, just without the ambition. I'm working on it. People always say, Mark, gotta be more confident. They say, Mark, gotta be yourself. I'm like, well, you gotta pick one.
Fresh off his Netflix special, Soup to Nuts, see Mark Normand live on stage this Saturday at Robinson Center. Get tickets now at Ticketmaster.com.
Roger Scott for Gravely Mowers. You know, when it comes to beautiful lawns, nothing cuts like a Gravely. And when it comes to cutting prices, there's nothing like the Gravely Mow the Distance sales event, where you can save up to 25%. And special financing is available on America's most rugged and dependable mowers, including their ZT-HD. It's the residential mower built to commercial standards. But hurry, because the Mow the Distance sale is only through April 8th and only at your authorized Gravely dealers like MPE in Sheridan or Gravel Ridge Small Engine in Jacksonville.
Welcome back to Morning Mayhem.
As far back as I can remember, I always wanted to be a gangster.
Live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios.
No, let me tell you something. Nobody goes to jail unless they want to.
Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
Look at me. Never rat on your friends and always keep your mouth shut.
Here is David Basil, Roger Scott, and Justin Moore.
All right, 7:06 here on Morning Mayhem. Thanks so much for being with us. We appreciate it. We're glad our signal strength, Roger, is back up to 100%. If that is correct, if you've been experiencing frustration with us, pop us a text and go, yes, I can tell the signal is better. Yeah. Thank you.
Yes. Justin was saying yesterday, what a novel idea.
You can hear us on the radio.
Yeah.
Anyway, I'm glad we got that done.
Yeah, we are too. Thanks to the company for thinking it necessary.
But we also appreciate those of you who listen and watch on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, our app.
For sure.
That's also an option. Coming up here shortly, Craig O'Neill, brought to you by Petty G Meat.
It's Craig Day.
That's exactly right. We got RJ Hawk. Coming up, Justin Moore should be jumping on with us here shortly.
And you're going to talk to Representative Hawk about streamlining the revenue office?
Exactly right, uh-huh. Roger. Yes. Yesterday, Razorbacks win 11 in a zip over the Trojans in seven innings. An outstanding performance by the pitching staff, Ben Bibee, Dylan Carter, Christian Fouch, and Stone Hewlett. Thank you. And it was two-hit shutout. And our man Peyton Stovall, Roger, another home run for him. He continues to play great. I was looking at his numbers. Where's if I made a note of that? I think he said 14 home runs in his 100 games that he's played as a Razorback, and he's hit I think three home runs already since he's been back. No softball last night between UCA and the Razorbacks. I guess because of the cold weather, they decided to postpone that and to reschedule it later. Looks like Arkansas State season is done, Roger.
Yeah.
They lose 81-80 to High Point in the CBI College Basketball Invitational down in Daytona Beach. We saw the end of that at trivia last night at Boudreaux's. I thought they were out of it. They were down by 10 or 12, and they come back and have a chance to win the game there at the end. The other big news is the kickoff in the NFL, and right. I want to wait till Justin jumps on here before we break that down, and Craig in studio as well. I wonder if people will like that or not. I think
I've heard some of it, and it's
it takes away some of
runbacks.
Yeah, it's something, Roger, to see people running full speed down the foot. You know, that's the only time you really see 10 guys going in each direction. Well, one
kamikaze.
Kamikaze. That's exactly what it is, Roger. The Mega Millions deal was won last night. $1.13 billion, fifth largest in the lottery history. It was in New Jersey. The winning numbers, Roger, 7, 11, 22, 29, 38, and the gold mega ball, 4. I have no idea what all that means.
Yes.
Yeah, you know all that.
Yes and no. I haven't done it in years.
A lot of
used to do it twice a week.
Sometimes the city of Little Rock gets a lot of negative national attention. I think sometimes unfairly.
Sure, they are.
But according to Southern Living magazine, their lifestyle magazine, Southern Living, they are in the top 25 current list of the South's best cities. So there you go.
I saw one a couple of weeks ago, if not last week, that said we were one of the. Say it had to do with being overweight and something like that.
Yeah, I mean, Arkansas is
who you are.
Arkansas has always struggled with that, Raj.
Well, it's not just Arkansas, but again, you make the poll whatever you want. That's why with AY Magazine we make up all the polls. They're all positive, and Arkansas is number one.
I will say, as far as like southern cities go, Little Rock's a pretty active city, though.
Yeah,
I mean, you have the River Trail. You always see people biking, running.
Yeah, I think so.
There's a million races happening all the time. It's a pretty active city.
I agree with that, and I think you have it's a beautiful.
Yeah, Northwest Arkansas is active too.
It is, and I think people get to. I think they come to Arkansas expecting something like, you know, it's going to be a small little farm town or something, and they see it's beautiful. You got rolling hills out there.
I would say Little Rock was in that aspect, like the active side of it was pleasant. Surprised how active of a city.
Right on.
Look at Justin. You see the Justin? Do you see the picture? Look at Kate. Wait, Kate just said it. That is hilarious. Holy cow.
Is he asleep?
Yes. He and South are sleeping on top of each other on a chair.
Justin Moore, 7:30. Sounds like.
It may be. Quentin Tarantino's birthday is today. Roger, how old do you think Quentin Tarantino is?
He is 50.
He is 61.
Yeah. What?
He's basically Irish. So what movie what movie do you think of for Quentin Tarantino? What is the movie?
The first one that comes to my mind is that the Hollywoods with.
Yeah, oh, my gosh.
You're not a huge Tarantino guy, are you?
I'm not, only because I don't know what a Tarantino movie is. I know Reservoir Dogs.
Inglourious Basterds.
Pulp Fiction.
Inglourious Basterds.
That was actually very violent.
That one's violent.
They're all violent.
They're the Sam Peckinpah of today.
Yeah, Hateful Eight. Remember that one?
I love that one.
Hateful Eight, once again.
Yes.
The violence and the bullets and everything.
Jackie Brown is one of the early ones. I've never seen Jackie Brown.
The
early ones, Natural Born Killers.
Natural Born Killers.
Is that with De Niro?
No, that's
Jackie Brown. No, De Niro's in Jackie Brown.
He is.
Yes.
Is Michael Keaton in that one?
Oh, I forget.
Who's the star of that?
Pam Grier.
Pam Grier. That's who is that? Yeah, she's the star.
Yeah, Michael Keaton's in that.
I have not seen it. Because I'm sitting there looking about Michael Keaton and Robert De Niro. I've never seen them together. And so I'll have to check that out. But Inglourious Basterds is fine. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood is my favorite.
Who?
So True Romance? So here's the thing about True Romance. He wrote True Romance.
True Romance.
So True Romance, it's him. It's Patricia Arquette and Christian Slater.
Oh, that, okay. I was
saying. Tony Scott directed. He loves, Tarantino loves Tony Scott.
What about Kill Bill? Volumes 1 and 2.
Yes.
I've just never, I don't know.
Oh, you don't love Kill Bill?
It's got Carradine in it. It's got the Kung Fu guy in it.
Yeah. And you know how he passed, don't you?
Who?
Carradine.
No.
I think it was asphyxiation.
Asphyxiation?
Yeah, in his own closet.
Let's go to, on that note, let's go to Justin Moore.
Speaking of that, here comes old Craig O'Neill.
Craig O'Neill and Justin Moore.
Hey, Jaber.
Have a seat, Craig.
On that note, Gregory. Go to me.
Yeah, listen, the minute that Craig walks in and Justin get on, we talk about asphyxiation.
Sexual asphyxiation. Yes, death.
Sexual asphyxiation.
David Carradine.
Asphyxiation, yes.
Well, last time I came in, y'all were singing the Zone of Totality.
The zone of totality, zone of totality, totality, totality.
And that song will be in my head, Justin, for the rest of the day. You
nice.
Not write Rick, music now, Justin, because it's going to be in your head
over,
all day. The worm is going to be squirming.
Well, if it is Wednesday, it's Craig O'Neill Day on Morning Mayhem. Yes.
Go.
One of the things I wanted to wait to talk about you guys with you guys, did you see the new rule for the NFL on kickoffs?
No.
Did you see it, Justin?
Is it two-hand touch now?
Close to that. Basically,
okay.
What it does.
So, I mean, it just keeps getting softer and softer.
So it takes the kickoff team, who is on one side of the 50 normally kicking off, the ball's on the 35. They're moving all those nine players, except the kicker, on the other side, on the return team side, to the 40-yard line. And then they put the return team, who's blocking, is on the 30 to 35. And nobody can move until the kickoff man catches the ball. And then it's hand-to-hand combat. Huh. They're not running. It's just hand-to-hand, and they got to get off their guy and make the tackle. Now, the guy who kickoff return, he may be running for 20 yards. He may catch in the end zone and run out, so he's got some momentum. But the kickoff team will not be running at full speed. They'll basically be just
waiting on it.
Roger Goodell has been bad for football.
Well, it's funny.
It's
funny, Justin. You've gotten two responses. You know, some obviously the defensive guys said, you know, what are we doing? This is flag football. And there apparently there was a guy from. No, I'm thinking of the tackle. What's that called, Josh?
The hip drop.
Tackle. Yeah, I'm thinking of the hip drop. You got the hip drop tackle that's been outlawed, and then you've got the kickoff. But you sort of knew this was coming on the kickoff. They just keep talking about it and talking about it. Listen, I mean,
they kick it out of the end zone every.
Well, that's true. That's
there
true.
There hadn't been a kickoff return in years now.
Well, listen.
And that's part of the game.
I know.
They literally took the kickoff and the kickoff return out of the game.
Well, listen, when I played, it was an honor to be on the wedge buster. I mean, you knew. Listen, I knew almost every time I did it, Justin. I was my head would be ringing, and I might be knocked silly. But I tell you, those five guys would be waiting on me. Yeah, pow! It's almost like bowling. You want to just see how much you can blow them up if you can.
Can we mark the tape on? Yeah, pow! Josh, thanks.
No telling how many concussions I probably got off that. But it was part of football. It was it was a fun thing.
You were ready for it.
I was ready for it. I would listen. You know, one of the guys brought up. One of the coaches said, "Well, listen, this is how some of our players get reps." They're not playing, and special teams would be, and so
gotta get that letter for your jacket.
If you're gonna wear the letter,
that's right.
I'm the wedge breaker.
That's it.
Yes,
you got a little wedge breaker insignia on the letter.
Yeah. Coming up shortly, we're gonna have a special guest call in, and we're exactly what is today? Wednesday to Wednesday, just a few days away from the 1 year anniversary of the tornado that hit, and obviously Justin Moore was really cool to step up and. Help raise money. Yeah. We got somebody call in and talk about that in a minute. What do you remember about that day, Craig?
I remember going in early. I remember watching Tom Brannon and Nathan Scott live on the air, and I remember their reaction as they saw live on the camera the tornado dip down, and I can still hear Nathan Scott on Channel 11 saying, "Oh, no. Oh, dear. There are going to be injuries. There's going to be damage. Oh, no. And this is not going anywhere anytime soon." And I can just... The drama in his voice and Tom's, too, because they both try to lighten it up.
Yeah.
But not that moment.
All three stations knew this is not going to be good. You know, highly dense area, and we've never seen one come through that area. So, I mean, ever. Usually you see them, you know, in small towns, but to have them right in the gut of the heartbeat, you know, of Little Rock, it was just a sort of a shocker deal.
It's miraculous yes. that there wasn't any
yeah, that's right.
any more injuries.
Or deaths, any deaths, yes.
Et cetera.
And I mean, my daughter, Justin, was in, my daughter was in the business known as Catering to You right across from Trios, right across from
yeah.
the pavilion in the park,
which took
dove into the walk-in freezer just as the tornado came over.
Wow.
And she still suffers
post-tornado yeah.
stress disorder.
Yeah, my girlfriend has the same issue that she gets. I mean, she went down the other day, whatever the tornado was, and she went down, even though it didn't look like it was going to be close, she went down in the cellar. She
really?
Just, yeah, listen, once you've been through that one time, mm-hmm. It's and of course, Roger, we were talking about, you talked to somebody last night, still didn't have some of their stuff.
Yeah,
that
still
they
don't have
still
some
shaking.
Of their stuff. Yeah.
Yeah.
Still don't
have
their stuff. I asked her if it was any insurance issue, and she said, no, not really. So, I mean, that's not something, because you mentioned that yesterday, you know, when we're talking
yeah,
about why there's still blue
yeah.
tarps on somebody. I don't know if some of these people live in apartments and maybe they didn't have insurance, renter's insurance. Maybe that's the reason why. Or on some of the homes, I would think, though, that if you have a home, whether you're the owner, or whether, or if you own it, whether you live in it and own it or you rent it, the owner of that, you would think insurance would cover a roof.
Yeah.
Immediately.
Mm. Yeah. It's anyway. So we're coming over to you. We'll visit with somebody here shortly that wants us to give a thank you to Justin.
While we're on weather, and since we're in the Oaklawn Casino studio,
Derby
Day, and since hold on. We're on weather. Did you see the exacta that happened over the weekend?
No.
All I thought about was my weather people at Channel 11. The weather, the all-weather exacta, the Arkansas forecast exacta. I think this was the last race on Saturday. I'm not real sure. But the winning horse was named Sunshine in 70. And the horse that came in second was Snow Flurry.
No way.
Outstanding.
Wow.
So
that's
we
nice.
Went from Sunshine and 70 to Snow Flurry.
It's Arkansas weather.
Arkansas weather.
Exactly right.
Well, but the next question, will you be at the Arkansas Derby? Does Craig O'Neill show up at the Derby?
My heart will be there. My wallet won't be.
It will not be. But listen, Roger, he doesn't have to be there with Oaklawn anywhere.
No, he doesn't.
Yes.
Ooh, what a
segue.
About
that?
You opened the door to that
Oaklawn
one.
Oaklawn anywhere.
That's what pays the bills right there. I will say, there's a group of people with the weather as it comes to weather who are still just like, tornado, let me go outside and check this out.
That's right. There's part of that.
Yeah, my daughter's wanting to let me know that maybe it's because of not enough crews and supplies. It's a year. So I would think mm-hmm. that a lot of folks would be coming in here now. But, I mean, it could still be true, Meredith.
Justin, have you ever been to the Arkansas Derby? Have you been to the big boy?
I don't think I have. I've been to Oaklawn a bunch,
sure,
obviously, but I don't think I've gone to the Derby.
Let me tell you, it is close. It's like
is it?
It's this Saturday. It
is.
Yes.
Is that the end of race season?
No, they continue all the way to May 5th. It's the last biggest. It's the biggest race of the year for mm-hmm. Oaklawn. It's the big daddy, and obviously the horse there obviously gets 200 points towards Kentucky Derby, mm-hmm. and so. But what it's like, it is like a Razorback game. I mean, there's 50,000 people there, and you're going to see a gazillion people you know. Infield is open. It's beautiful. Oh. I mean, it is the biggest event other than a Razorback game. I mean, I think
the reason I asked you last night when trivia was is because I turned 40 Saturday.
Yes.
And,
yes.
We were talking about going over like one night. And
come on.
Maybe stay in the night.
Mm-hmm. Come on. We don't get
we never stayed over at Oaklawn.
That's best.
And so we thought, what better way to do it than mm-hmm. go the night that Raj does trivia?
Yes, that would be outstanding.
That,
so. Yeah, it was
terrific.
Monster
family entertainment.
And we'll see if Justin
Burns
and Kate could actually maybe vie for a title in trivia. Craig, king of all trivia, we call him Coat, KOAT, king of all trivia.
That's right.
He doesn't throw it easy.
I can't. Well, who do you think I am? I'm just going to give them to you. What are you going to learn from that, Craig?
No.
You're not going to learn anything.
Throw Craig.
You
know and throw Craig.
Listen, when it was stump, when you did your stump to state.
Uh-huh.
You didn't give out. It was it.
That's it.
You win or you don't.
Throw out the question
or no
to Craig and to Justin. Throw out the shot deal. The
okay. There are three, and I don't have it in front of me, but I want to say it's semaglutide. Let's just say that. That's the name. If I'm getting it close, that's the name of the company that has three weight loss
diabetes medications out there. One is Ozempic.
Right.
What are the other two?
Well, you got me.
Okay. Sure. Okay. Justin, I gave you that. That's what I'm saying. I said, who knows that?
That's right.
Who knows that info, Justin?
The chick's there, dude.
Let's see if Justin does.
If
Justin,
you're having to go to the fine print on the medicine bottle.
Yes.
That's just for a trivia question.
It's for weight loss is what, right? Right.
It's diabetes and they discovered it. And then from what Donnie Anderson told them.
Yeah. Go ahead.
No, you go ahead, buddy. I'm sorry.
One of them is the one that everybody's been taking to lose weight.
That's what I thought. That's Mangiaro.
Kilimanjaro. Okay, but that's not under that.
That's not under that.
So here's the thing. Jay Bird, let me tell you this. I knew it was a tough question, but the chick faction in your team came through in a lot of those things. The other part of it is I gave one of the answers as your free answer. So you were going to get some points for that one. I wasn't just going to screw you. Now, the other two are...
Go ahead, say it. You remember?
Wegovy.
Wegovy.
W-E-G-O-V-Y.
All right.
And Rebelsis.
I'll
never forget those.
Yeah. No. We're talking about the... Rebelsis.
Justin, listen, I look around.
Well, no, you wouldn't get them. Well, listen.
I've never heard those words.
All right, Justin.
Life.
All right, here, Justin. Either. All right, here's another one. Let me do this for you. Listen, this was a bottom tier question. I've got to start weeding out the wimps in this one. The first question in the theme song to Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, where was the main character born and raised?
Okay, you got me on that
on
one,
the playground
too.
Is where he spent most of his days.
Where?
Come on, Justin. Finish it out.
In West Philadelphia.
Bingo.
Oh, but Justin got it. See, Greg, I didn't get it.
I never watched
it. I didn't either.
Show.
Okay. Well, see,
In West Philadelphia, born and raised on the playground is where I spent most of my days.
See, that was an easy one.
That was easy.
So, Craig, so what happened? I'm like you. I didn't watch that. But then you start hearing everybody in there start singing.
Yes,
wow.
Yes.
I missed out on that. But
so we just change it up. What if James Ballantyne wants me to give him all the Ted Danson questions?
I did. Okay, let's go to Craig. Let's go to Craig and Justin on this. All right, Craig will get this. Justin will not. Right. Name the actress, Craig and Justin.
That is so insulting, by the way, when you say that. I know you don't mean it that way, but you go, he'll get it. He won't.
I don't think he will.
No.
I know. Just
Craig will.
Who played the little child who became...
In The Exorcist.
In The Exorcist.
The original.
That became possessed.
What was the actress's
possessed.
Name? Yeah, the actress's name.
I got that one. This is one of the one I one of
you
the
sure
few
did,
I got last
you
night.
Because you dated chicks like this, you said.
I'll give you the initials. LB. LB, Craig. Come on. You should get this.
Laura Blair.
Yes.
Blair?
Yes! Blair's the last name. First name. L.
It's not Linda.
Yes, that's it. Good job. You worked your way through it, Craig.
You pulled that one.
You got your way. Justin, that's a tough one unless you're 60 years old.
You were helping me across the street.
Yeah.
Okay.
I did want to mention real quick, we've mentioned it several times, Arkansas dominates last night on the mound against the Trojans. This is what Chris Curry, the head coach who actually coached under Dave Van Horn for a year or two up in Fayetteville in 2009 and 10. Said Arkansas, quote, Arkansas just has an embarrassment of riches for arms. Quote, their depth is as good as it's ever been. It may be the best pitching staff they've ever had. Two-hit shutout last night with four pitchers. They just continue to do it on the mound.
Yeah, but we lost it against Auburn, but you can't complain because you'd won, what, 15
that's
in
right,
a row?
That's right, 15 in a row.
So
that's right.
Don't complain. Yeah. Let Auburn have it.
And then our guy.
They really should have won that game, too. Though.
Had a chance to win that one, had the lead.
I mean, they were up, what,
5-1?
5-1. Yeah,
and then Peyton Stovall, who we talk to every Tuesday, hit another home run yesterday, so that was encouraging to see. And then listen, this weekend in Fayetteville, baby, got LSU.
Come on,
LSU Thursday night, and
come on, corn dogs, bring it.
Listen, LSU is ranked number 7. I'm not sure there'll be a better atmosphere. Who do you think, Justin, will be the better atmosphere, LSU or Tennessee? How bad you hate
everybody because of the
coaching,
the little spat. Like
yes.
3, 4, 5 years ago,
right?
Yes.
Whenever it was, everybody hates Tennessee.
Craig, it's all
because they hate the coach.
That's right. That's right. There's a narrative there, but it'll be hopping this weekend.
They'll both be great.
Yeah.
My son-in-law is from Texas, and Tennessee beat Texas the other night in the NCAA, and he was just my son-in-law was distraught. He's a Longhorn fan, And I said, well, at least you don't have to sit there and listen to Rocky Top over and over and over. The, that is awful.
The other, the well, it's funny watching that game, Roger. We'll go ahead and take a break if you want to. We got to play both those orange teams in Fayetteville this year in football.
Oh, how
both those
cool
orange
is
teams.
That?
Which orange do we hate the most, Justin? What do you think? The burnt orange or the?
I hate Texas worse, do you? Personally. But
yeah, I'd probably say so. I would probably think so because we have a history there.
My son-in-law's from Texas. He's produced two wonderful grandchildren. I love that family down in Texas. So I've kind of mellowed on them. So it's Tennessee because I stood on that field in 2000 and watched Houston Nutt's team get beat. What was it, 60-20?
Oh,
60
you were
to
there in Knoxville for
and,
that? Oh my gosh!
Ever
that was,
since,
oh, that was bad.
Bring it.
That was one of the worst losses in the history of the program. Mm-hmm. They just ran us. And of course, then we come back and have the great game when they decided the national championship.
That was at 99.
I'm just talking
tore
about
down the goal
just talking about the comparison between the two. Yeah, just,
I thought 99's the fumble, stumble and fumble.
It was, but it was a great game.
98.
2000. Okay, yeah. 98.
Yeah, it was an unbelievable game. But it just goes to show you the waves of success and failure that sometimes used
year
to would
to
have.
Year.
Yeah, that from one year you.
Craig.
Yeah.
I love you, but. You can't soften up on Texas just because
you gotta
still hate them.
Oh, when they take the field and start, we hear the Texas fight.
The fight, listen, I'm there. As a player, Craig, Texas fight was the worst. If you heard that song over and over again. Yeah, it is. Oh, my gosh. It's so obnoxious. It is so obnoxious.
Gets me going, though.
It does. I just noticed that. All right, 7:30 here, Morning Mayhem.
Registration is open for the 2024 1037 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament, Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course, presented by Tito's Handmade Vodka.
This is SportsCenter.
Arkansas Razorbacks baseball cruised to an 11-0 win yesterday over in-state rival Little Rock. Ben Bibee, Dylan Carter, Christian Fouch, and Stone Hewitt combined to throw his 7 innings of shutout baseball. Bibee struck out 5 of the 10 batters that he faced. And on the day, Vahiva Aloy, the shortstop for the Hogs, drove in 4 runs as well. The Hogs are now 20-3 overall. They host number 8 LSU this weekend in a Thursday, Friday, Saturday series. First game is 6 p.m. on Thursday. Second game is 7 o'clock. On Friday. The series finale is at 2 p.m. on Saturday afternoon. Arkansas softball had their game against UCA canceled due to cold temperatures. I'm Josh Neighbors for the Buzz Radio Network.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Another sunny but cool day with a high of just 62 degrees. Not as windy as yesterday, though, and tonight's low will drop back down to about 39. A little warmer tomorrow at 68 and low 70s back by Friday. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Join the Zone each Monday for Game Balls and Jockstraps. Brought to you by A. Caddy's Touch Landscaping. Find out who made the best, average, and worst headlines in sports and entertainment each Monday as Justin Akery and Wes Moore give you their Game Balls and Jockstraps on the Zone from 10 to 1. It's all brought to you by A. Caddy's Touch Landscaping, 501-794-2770. Call today to get your landscape updated to a whole new level and be listening for Game Balls and Jockstraps only on 103.7 The Buzz.
This is the time of year to enjoy life. Stop letting that pain in your joints keep you from doing what you want to do this spring. Call QC Kinetics now. QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. I'm talking about lasting joint relief with no surgery, no drugs, and no downtime. Hey everybody, it's RJ Hawk. It's a fact. QC Kinetics is literally transforming lives. Their advanced treatments harness your own body's ability to restore and repair damaged joint tissue. Pro athletes have been doing this for decades. But now, this life-changing treatment is available to you, so you can walk and run and climb stairs and play golf and just move again, all pain-free. No pain pills, no risky surgery. This is an all-natural solution. QC Kinetics has tens of thousands of satisfied patients and people right here in Central Arkansas. Call QC Kinetics for that free consultation. 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440.
What do you do when the power goes out? Well, now you can do anything you want when you purchase a Generac home standby generator from Generator Supercenter of Little Rock. Come visit the experts at Central Arkansas' only generator showroom located on Chenal Parkway in West Little Rock. We offer a turnkey solution, financing, and 24/7 service. Visit our website for more info at GeneratorSupercenterOfLittleRock.com. The standby power people.
Red tape. One in three businesses will get caught up in it, and they'll be penalized by the IRS for mismanaging their payroll. Because when you're handling payroll, HR compliance, and those constantly changing tax laws, that red tape can get sticky in a hurry. At The Payroll Company, we free you from that tangled mess and get you back to business. The Payroll Company. Less headaches, more than payroll. Visit morethanpayroll.com to learn more.
Let's keep the good vibes going. Morning Mayhem is back on the air. Live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios. Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
Five guys be waiting on me.
Pow! Can we mark the tape on?
He's a legend in the state of Arkansas.
Where? See, if y'all run out of the field, it's going to say, yeah. Texas.
His 55 years in television and radio broadcasting is unparalleled.
His name is Craig O'Neill.
He has helped raise over $9 million for charity. Brought to you by Petty Jean Meats. Petty Jean Meats, locally owned and operated for four generations. Yoo-hoo! With Petty Jean Meats, people always know where their meat is coming from.
Oh, yeah.
Made right here in Arkansas. Please welcome Craig O'Neill.
This Wednesday is Craig O'Neill Day. Woo! On Morning Mayhem.
Easter hams, baby. Get your Petty Jean hams.
That's right. We mentioned Arkansas Derby Easter Sunday, obviously, next day. Big weekend. And, you know, talking about $9 million that you've helped raise all through all your MC gigs over the years, really impressive. Want to go to the Hodges Glass, Little Rock Glass Hotline. And I had no idea that you knew Heather Larkin, who is the CEO of the Arkansas Community Foundation. I had no idea.
Heather and I were an item.
We were
an item.
Wow.
For a couple of years, weren't we, Heather?
We were, Craig. We were.
Heather, first we got to say happy birthday. It's your birthday today.
Oh, wow.
How about that?
Happy birthday, Heather.
30.
Thank you.
30.
That's right. Yeah.
Well, first of all, Heather, tell everybody who's listening what the Arkansas Community Foundation is.
The Arkansas Community Foundation is a foundation that works in all 75 counties in Arkansas, mm-hmm. helping build communities where our kids want to raise their kids.
Mm-hmm. And you're calling today because we're coming up on the one-year anniversary of the tornado that hit Central Arkansas, and when?
That's right. Almost 1 year ago, we had a devastating tornado. A couple of tornadoes hit Arkansas. And Arkansans rose to the occasion, and I'm proud to say that although there is work still to be done, we've come a long way in helping those communities recover.
Wow. And what was the name, what was sort of the goal when the tornado hit? And I know obviously we've got somebody on this show who contributed towards that effort. Remind us exactly how that came together.
That's right. Well, when a disaster like that hits, there's several stages of recovery. Immediate relief, you know, water and things like that, and then intermediate recovery, and then long-term recovery. The Community Foundation focuses on intermediate and long-term recovery, which means we do things not like delivering water bottles, but helping people rebuild and communities become more resilient. Over a short period of time, the Community Foundation received over $1 million for those recovery efforts, and 100,000 of that was thanks to you all and to Justin for the two Little Rock with Love concerts. It was a huge success. All that money has been deployed back into Central Arkansas and to Cross County for intermediate and long-term recovery.
Mm. Well, that's I'll never get Justin. Roger, you remember Craig. It was Justin got together some of his buddies.
other artists to sing, and it was, the place was packed. But Roger, the thing I remember, and I've got it on video, I was stage right, was when Colin Ray sang Little Rock, and Justin, listen, I love it when one artist appreciates another artist, you know, ability, and obviously you have a lot of respect for Colin Ray. But that night when everybody in the room started saying Little Rock, it was that really was a special part of that night.
Great guy, and loves Arkansas, and obviously grew up here. And for him to, you know, take time to come do that was really cool. Oh,
well, and if Craig, you didn't know this, but Roger, if I don't know if you can find it, how quick you can find it. Justin actually did two concerts, as Heather Larkin said. The first one was over at the hall. The second one was I think it was Sticky Fingers, and the Buzz was involved with that. And that brought together.
Yeah, that was a Buzz event.
Yeah, that brought together two of the greatest singers ever, and both Justin Moore and Randy Rainwater.
And myself.
Randy, we convinced Randy. Randy was one of.
I got boots that night.
Justin
J.M.
He actually gave him boots, cowboy boots, and a hat, and he got up there, and he'd been working on a song all week. It was Roger. You got it. It was, I think it was a Kenny Rogers song, right?
Campbell.
Glenn Campbell.
Glenn Campbell, that's what it was. Justin had to help him a little bit. I thought the mic
I've
was
been walking these streets alone, singing the same old song.
That's Glenn Campbell.
There it is, right there. So that was a special night too. Well, Heather, it's hard to believe it's been a year since the tornadoes hit. Thanks for what you guys did and continue to do throughout the state. And it, as you said, it takes a lot of people like Justin to step up and raise, I think, $100,000 that night. But it was really neat to see our Arkansans come together.
Let me tell you, I'll share you all. Go ahead, Heather. I'm sorry I'm interrupting.
Well, I just wanted to say it's a terrible event in Arkansas, but it was really special to be a part of the recovery. And so grateful to all of you for what you did.
Wonderful.
And Craig, like I said, you have a history there with Heather.
In the spring.
We've raised a lot of money, haven't we?
We did. And it was in April, 2016 and 17, somewhere back in there before COVID. Mm-hmm. And there have been two times I've cried live on air.
Oh, wow.
And one of them was when we hit that goal live on the air for the Arkansas Community Foundation of, I think it was $2 million. In the spring, we're right around tax season. It's not a time where you traditionally fundraise, and there we were raising that money in one day.
Yeah.
And
isn't Arkansas a special place?
Oh, man.
Well, Heather, thanks for jumping on with us today and obviously reminding us. And happy birthday to you.
Hey, thank you, guys, and y'all be good.
Thank you. Listen, Heather, it takes people like Heather to get out and do those things, to organize stuff.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, Double R. Thank you. You could have done what she was on, Randy.
So, Craig, the other time that you cried was your last time on the air, right?
Last time
on
the air.
I saw you get
I got emotional. And I got emotional when I introduced my wife.
I saw that, yes.
And brought Jane on, and she was off.
She wasn't emotional at all. She's like, come on.
She was on. It was her show.
Well, she's been waiting all these years to get you off the mic, and she was ready.
Craig, just go home. it's enough already. Just go home.
Come with me.
We were talking during the break too. During the break, Justin and Roger, I think you stepped out about the Texas game that where we'd beaten Texas, and you asked me. You said, were you there?
Well, I wondered if you. It suddenly dawned on me you were a fresh. You might have been a freshman.
I was a freshman in '81 when we beat the dog at him. And Roger, I have to tell him the Lou Holtz.
Absolutely did.
So Watch down.
That's Justin's son, South.
That's my boy right there.
He's got him doing this.
Watch down.
So Lou comes in the locker room, Craig, and nobody gives us a chance to win that week. Nobody. We'd heard that Aris Parsegian was doing the game, and he was like, listen, it might have been Keith Jackson, too. I know it was Aris Parsegian for sure. It might not have been Keith Jackson. But anyway, nobody thought we could beat him. They were number one in the nation. We were probably. So Lou came in there, and he said, all right, man, when the national media comes in this locker room after the game is over, you tell me it was not enough. And we obviously beat him 42-11. It was 21-0 at halftime, and it was.
I remember.
Let me tell you, like you said, everything they did was a fumble or a mistake,
it
was
not get everything. Out of their own way.
Justin, it was an epic.
Did that fire y'all up when he
oh,
said?
Oh man!
Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Of course he
I
was.
I mean, that fires me up just hearing.
Yeah, he. Of course, you remember what he said on the Catholics versus the convicts, where he said, "You leave Jimmy Johnson's ass to me. You go out there and beat them. Leave Jimmy Johnson's ass to me." Yeah. You know, he was so good at preparing for the big games. And I tell you, to hate Texas as bad as we did and to beat them like that, it was similar to what we did a few years ago in Fayetteville. I mean, we dominated that game with under the Pittman era, and it just doesn't happen very often. We talked about the game down in Austin where Matt Jones.
Yeah,
just I think they were number 5 in the nation when we beat them.
I had forgotten that.
Yeah, I think they were a top 10 team, and it doesn't happen often. If you look at the history, the record, it does it. But so you would think, Justin, you still feel Texas would be the number one most hated?
Points down!
And LSU number 2, you think, most hated?
I mean, probably. It would be up to each person to say. But for me, yes, because I grew up – when I first started watching the Razorbacks, we were in the Southwest Conference still. And my dad just taught me, like – no matter what, we hate them.
That's a daddy raising his boy right. Yeah, that's exactly what happens there. I did want to ask, too.
I was going to say, in 1959, I sat in the north end zone at the age of 9 and watched Texas beat Arkansas 13-12 after scoring after a fumble by Lance Allworth on a punt.
You saw that game?
In Warren Memorial Stadium.
You saw Lance Allworth play.
And sat there and cried. And cried and cried, and the whole stadium could hear me, because when I cried, everybody could hear it, and I wasn't on the PA. And the only way my father could get me to shut up was to go down on the field and meet the players, because back then you could. And Jim Moody, I'll never forget it, All-American for Frank Royals, I think it was his first, comes off hobbling off the field. He'd been hurt. He sees me crying, and he pats me on the head.
How cool is that?
And I was cured.
Wow, I've never heard you tell that story.
It's in the book.
The book's coming out soon. Well, you saw the great Lance Allworth.
I did see him play.
Many consider, along with McFadden, the greatest Razorback and Clyde Scott, those would be the three probably great. Goes on to be one of the greatest receivers in NFL history.
And he, oddly enough, he kind of reminded me of Matt Jones, because he had that long stride, and he was so much more nimble and quicker than Matt Jones. But nonetheless, he was so fast. So athletic, and came to Arkansas because he was married at he married a girl that was 16.
And Roger, what is the nickname of the great Lance Allworth?
Bambi
is correct. Bambi. All right, here's the deal. When we come back for the break, this last segment with Craig, I want you to go to the cameras, because I noticed something in Craig's pocket, and I want Craig to pull it out and then tell us.
Tommy's not on here anymore.
Go to the webcam
the hell's
now.
Wrong with you?
YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, go, because he's going to pull out something. I think it's going to be historic when he pulls it out.
Yes!
What? Wow! It just keeps getting worse.
7:45.
Roger Scott for Oaklawn Racing Casino Resort. Are you tired of feeling like a lonely raccoon in the dark? Well, say goodbye to those gloomy nights and hello to the Oaklawn Eclipse Festival, shining bright from April 4th to April 8th. And get ready to bask in the glow of family, fun, and affordability all weekend long. We've got you some horse racing action hotter than a jalapeno salsa, and not one, but 2 Mitsubishi Eclipses are up for grabs. And for all you stargazers out there, come catch the glimpse of the eclipse from our legendary Oaklawn infield. Tickets for the April 8th infield event are a steal at just $20. And you know Oaklawn's Event Center is cooking up some sizzling entertainment for you. Mitchell Tenpenny on Saturday, April 6th, followed by Better Than Ezra on Sunday, April 7th. And get ready to laugh, sing, and dance with Terry Fader, Gary Allen, and Aaron Lewis on various dates throughout the year. And boy, howdy, stay tuned, because we've got more big announcements and headliners coming. Snatch up your tickets and book your rooms at Oaklawn.com today. It's all happening in beautiful Hot Springs, home to Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
Mart.
The all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock is now open. Over 100,000 square feet of hardware, outdoor, appliances, a window and door center, and even a drive-through lumber yard. And there's nothing like Design One. This stunning showroom is one place for all your home and design needs, including 12 full kitchens and 9 baths, plus a huge selection of lighting, flooring, countertops, and more. At the all-new Lumber One and Design One, now open in West Little Rock.
It's Pat Bradley for Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, where their customers are always number one. Speaking about numbers, 6% APY is still available at Alcoa. Earn up to 6% interest on your checking account balances for doing the things you already do, like using your debit card and direct deposit. You can also get your ATM fees waived. Apply today for your free Kasasa checking account and earn up to 6% APY at alcoacommunityfcu.org. Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, serving Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry Counties.
Calling all basketball fans, our season is here. We know that this time of year, traveling fouls can happen anywhere and anytime. That's why All About Tire and Brake Tire Pros is the MVP of tire service and savings. Our expert, certified technicians are the community's number one trusted choice for any tire or service need, with the goal of making sure you're not stuck on the bench. Visit in stores in Mapleville or Little Rock, online at allabouttireandbrake.com. Tire Pros, love the drive.
At ABC Supply, when you've got a job to do, we do too. When your success depends on getting the details right, we're there for you every step of the way. Delivering more than materials, delivering passion, commitment, and the confidence to help you get the job done easier. Our teams understand the obstacles you face in building your business and reputation, because living up to our promises is how we help you live up to yours.
For location and product information, call ABC Supply North Little Rock at 501-955-0777 or visit abcsupply.com.
Spring has sprung, and that spells fun. Fun is in Arts Marine in North Little Rock. Arts has new 2024 G3 Tritunes. That's right, I said Tritunes, in stock. And as always, don't forget Arts Marine is your John Boat headquarters. They're powered by Tohatsu and Yamaha outboards. Arts also has an excellent selection of the ever-so-popular G3 boats, models 22, 23, and 2024. Make your summer one to remember by stopping by Arts Marine in North Little Rock. Take the Levy exit.
Now's the time to get a great deal on proven Kubota farming equipment. Tractors that are adaptable, versatile, and rated number one in durability and owner experience. Hay tools that are backed by a 2-year warranty. And durable Sidekick utility vehicles and SVL track loaders. Right now, bring home select Kubota equipment for zero down, 0% APR for up to 48 months, now through March 31st. Visit KubotaUSA.com for full details. Hennard Foothills Equipment, South Main Street in Searcy. Your hometown Kubota dealer, no matter where you live.
Oaklawn Racing Casino Resort presents Oaklawn Race Day with Justin Akery and David Wanginati every Saturday morning at 11. Oaklawn Race Day is your inside track to America's hottest thoroughbred action and Arkansas source for racing news and analysis. Oaklawn Race Day, presented by Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
Want to reach the show? Well, give us a call or text at 501-661-1037. Welcome back to Morning Mayhem.
What'd you hear?
Beats German soldiers with a club.
He bashes the brains in with a baseball bat, what he does. Hey, Werner, I'm going to ask you one last time. If you still respectfully refuse, I'm calling the bear Jew over.
The bear
Jew. He's
going
to take that big bat of his, and he's going to beat your ass to death with it. Take your wiener schnitzel licking finger and point out on this map what I want to know.
You.
And your dogs.
Actually, Warner, we're all tickled to hear you say that. Quite frankly, watching Donnie beat Nazis to death is close we ever get to going to the movies. Donnie!
Yeah?
Guy's German here, wants to die for country. Oblige him.
Oblige him. That's Inglourious Basterds, obviously, by Quentin Tarantino.
Wow.
Remember he got Christoph Waltz two Academy Awards.
Yeah, back to back and belly to belly.
Both for
Inglourious Basterds, right?
Yeah, Django Unchained, yeah, two supporting actors.
That's a Tarantino movie I like because it's got some funny scene. Whoever thought the KKK would have a funny
Yeah,
I mean, that's so good. No one's saying.
The legend Craig O'Neill here in the studio with us, brought to you by Petty G Meats. Now, Craig, I noticed when you came in, if you go to the webcam right now,
yes,
or any of our cams, you'll see Craig, you had a little book in your pocket, and I thought, I have a funny feeling that looks like an idea book.
It is an idea book.
And it is. And so how long have you carried this idea book?
Well, actually, I've carried it this year. This is this year's
idea book.
Oh, that's
just this year. Wow.
Just since January.
It looks like it's been handled for 40 years. Well, I mean, look at it. The pages are worn out, and it looks old, and it's only a year. So that thing is full. You've got notes. You want to open it up and just show the notes there?
Well, let's see. And I'm actually reading from this book, and I'll start in the very last one entered.
This is an NIL idea that you pitched towards that we didn't give you the support you needed?
These are ideas for – I do a face cast on Facebook, and these are ideas for that. For instance, do PA announcements trying to improve our culture. For instance, here's a PA announcement idea. Your attention, please. If you use a towelette to wipe down the shopping cart, please throw the towelette away and don't leave it in the bottom of the cart. Thank you.
Yeah, you gotta tell people. Okay. Very nice, all right. Very nice.
Okay. Time magazine issued an article about women who saved the United States from help me.
They said women saved.
Women saved the country from the economy starting to falter.
Depression.
Wasn't depression.
Black market.
Recession. I'm sorry.
I blame myself.
Okay. Go ahead. Yes. But it was an interesting article because women were working from home. They were earning money while working from home during the pandemic. And because they had that money and that buying power, they bought things online. They worked from home, primarily women who had versatile schedules, and they saved the country from recession.
Okay.
So, women, congratulations.
About time they went to work. They ought to be in there barefoot and pregnant and cooking.
Thank you, ladies. Yes.
With that in mind, here's another one. This is Coach Roy Lee, Peter Ball, Rooster Poot High School football coach. We got a controversy up there at Rooster Poot. We've had cutbacks because of times being hard, so we're now having to teach driver's ed and sex ed out of the same car.
Very nice, coach. So you're just rolling down the road, and all of a sudden you get an idea.
I don't roll down the road.
He pulls over.
You pull over.
Arkansas State Police safety.
How many of those booklets do you have, Craig? Do you have one every year?
No, this is the first year actually.
Because really?
In news, you wrote down stories. Story ideas, but now that I'm back to being radio star.
Yes. Absolutely. I love it.
I love that idea. Listen, if I wrote down half the some of the stuff here, we can't write down because it could be used against us.
And one more.
Yes.
And this one is for those of you watching who happen to be watching, my impression of a guy who's just had a foul called on him in the NCAA tournament.
Yeah, there it is. Yeah, every basketball player does.
What? No!
Yes.
Very good.
Speaking of a tournament, do you have anybody that you're paying attention to?
Now I'm pulling. I find myself pulling for, believe it or not, Houston.
Okay.
Because they beat Texas A&M, who I was pulling for, and that was a phenomenal.
That was a great game.
It was. Oh my gosh!
Yeah. Kevin Sampson,
Craig, you were rooting for Texas A&M.
Yes.
Why?
Because we beat them twice. And secondly, they'd come on so strongly, and that one player, Mark, who was just phenomenal with his three-point shots and almost brought A&M back against Arkansas in Fayetteville, had just caught fire.
See, Craig, what you're going to learn, Roger, Justin has a little bit different approach than all of us, Craig. So, and Roger, if you can find the spot, it's
Basil. Were you rooting for the Aggies?
No, no, I was not rooting for the Aggies.
Don't say it's different than you.
Well, I'm just saying you're more passionate about this probably than any of us on this. Is that his dislike for everything non-Razorback is the strongest? And one time, Roger was talking about. Listen, if you're an Ole Miss fan out there or if you're a Texas fan and you're listening to our show, love for you to call in.
Right.
And then Justin responded to, you're not going to find it, Raj?
No.
Yeah, listen, anyway, if we can find that clip, Justin.
Craig, I simply said, don't call in and turn the radio station and don't listen.
Yeah, he basically said, don't call in. If you're Ole Miss, don't call in. We don't want you calling in. And so but that's
I don't want to hear from you. I still don't want to hear from you.
You know, they're
out there listening right now. Turn the station. I don't want to hear from you.
The other thing today was, I don't know if you knew this, today we have all these national days. Today was National Quirky Country Music Song Title Day.
Wow.
So I was going to say, what? Just, yes, it's National Country,
Quirky
Country Music Song Title today. And they were trying to think, Justin,
did
what?
Did list some?
Well, no, it did not. It's just that I looked on it at the list and I didn't think of one. And Roger brought up
Ray Stevens
did most of the
Can't Roller Skating the Buffalo Herd, or there was, one,
was
something
Roger
about. Or excuse me, Roger Miller. Stevens did some as well. Roger Miller was great.
The Street.
Yeah. Who was a bubblegum on the bedpost?
Red Solo Cup.
Red Solo Cup. That.
What?
Okay.
What do you, Justin? Do you have a? Do you have one song? Song title that's
more
interesting.
More Middle Finger.
Yeah, I mean, that would be
that. That is, you know, have you heard that one? More Middle Finger. It is. It's one of Roger and I's favorite Justin Moore songs.
Yeah.
He doesn't always play it at the concerts, but it's.
No, it's a nice little salute if you can get away with it.
Yeah, it's. Listen, we were talking about.
Beta Hook, maybe?
Beta Hook?
Is that quirky?
Oh, that ain't quirky. That's real talk.
That's unique. It's a unique song title.
Listen, I don't want to hurt nobody's feelings, but it's, listen. This one, listen
this
to the word.
This one's for the IRS in bed with the damn politicians. And this one's for the boss of horse who wouldn't let you off to go fishing. And to the bulls and the bears on Wall Street, taking you and me to the cleaners. Man, stuff like that that made me wish I had.
Let them fly in the sky.
Let them flip like you don't give a rip, like your mama ain't there.
Like your mama ain't there.
I could use a few for the dude in the suit who cut me off in his brand new Beamer. And it's stuff like that to make me wish I had
more middle finger. Yeah,
that's a great
one.
Also, Kate brought up Back That Thing Up. Back That Thing Up. That's a unique one, too.
What about Badonka Donk? That's one, isn't it?
Raise that finger if you see.
On that song with me, More Middle Fingers. He's actually coming to my house today, and we're recording another song.
Oh, together. That's right. Oh, wow. You shared that
that's
about
weird.
That.
Baz and I are coming to your house today.
Wow.
Craig O'Neill, outstanding work as always.
Thank you, Craig, with you and your book.
Thanks
raise
to Penny
your
Jimmy.
Finger as you sit in the bleacher. Don't worry about somebody saying something to the preacher.
Nobody's going to do it.
Boom.
Nobody's going to do it.
Boom.
The tape.
And you're going with us to Justin's house.
I learned today how crazy I am.
I know. You've got a Morning Mayhem t-shirt.
He's got a Morning Mayhem shirt.
You're
official. That's
official.
It right there, yes.
Look
we
that.
Want you
look
to put that.
That
on. Look, thank you to Steve Qualls and Design Lab in Hot Springs, Arkansas. That's got new car smell on it, Craig. That's got the tag
Greg.
Still
awesome.
On it.
Awesome, outstanding.
Thank
you're the
you,
man.
Sir.
Great to have you on the Morning Mayhem
it
team.
It is indeed.
Thanks to Petty G Meats as well.
Yeah, we may have to keep him on 2 hours.
Happy Arkansas Derby Day and have a great Easter, Craig. Thank you, buddy.
All
right.
Too.
8
love
o'clock.
You.
Easter, Craig. Man, have a great week.
You too.
Roger Scott for Family Markets. Are you tired of the same old grocery store experience? Then it's time to switch things up and shop at the neighborhood Family Markets in Pangburn, Malvern, and Shannon Hills. Our stores offer a unique shopping experience where we know our customers by name and offer a wide selection of fresh, locally sourced meats and produce. And you can even grab you a hot cup of community coffee while you're there. On selected items, you can mix and match any 5 items for only $24.99. And if you're a Valero gasoline customer, store points on your Family Markets reward card and redeem them at the pump to lower your price per gallon at select stores. At your neighborhood Family Markets, we're committed to providing a personalized shopping experience that's focused on our customers. So come on down and see why we're the best choice for your grocery needs. With fresh food, great deals, and friendly service, we're sure you're going to love shopping at the neighborhood Family Markets. So come on, stop by today and check us out. We're the Family Markets, with stores located in Pangburn, Malvern, and Shannon Hills. The way grocery shopping is supposed to be. Family Markets.
You can hear the best of the NCAA tournament on 106.7 Buzz 2 from the very beginning all the way to the championship game. March Madness on 103.7 The Buzz and 106.7 Buzz 2.
One man can't make a team.
Yeah, so what's your point?
Thanks for being part of the Buzz team.
Shut up!
103.7 The Buzz.
Buzz News with Channel 7's Cassandra Webb.
Little Rock Mayor Frank Scott Jr. is among 21 mayors who will travel to Memphis today, joining the Black Mayors Coalition on Crime and its efforts to reduce violent crime in America's cities. Memphis Mayor Paul Young launched the effort in partnership with the African American Mayors Association. Young took office in Memphis earlier this year and says a high-profile national movement of mayors could help solve ongoing issues with crime. According to a recent Gallup poll, voters' concerns about crime are at their highest level since 2016. Local businesses are stocking their shelves ahead of the total solar eclipse. Edwards Food Giant is preparing for an increased volume of customers looking to buy meat, bread, and other staple items for the eclipse. They plan on getting some trucks ahead of time with all those groceries. Cavanaugh Pharmacy is also getting necessities in case of an emergency. They'll have Band-Aids, Neosporin, antiseptic, and all other health items. Both stores will carry NASA-approved solar eclipse glasses while supplies last. From the Channel 7 Newsroom, I'm Cassandra Webb.
Presented by Gary Hill with MSS Oil, Splash Car Wash. There hasn't been an oil man specialist like this since Who Shot JR. Call Gary Hill with MSS Oil at 501-200-7089.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Another sunny but cool day with a high of just 62 degrees. Not as windy as yesterday, though, and tonight's low will drop back down to about 39. A little warmer tomorrow at 68 and low 70s back by Friday. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
It's grass cutting time, which means it's also time for the annual Gravely Mowers Spring Tour, which Morning Mayhem will be kicking off at Triple C Sales and Service in Conway this Thursday morning, where you can take advantage of their special Mow the Distance sales event and save up to 25% off retail price. So join David and Roger at Triple C in Conway this Thursday morning.
Life isn't just about living, it's about living well. And no one understands that better than Baptist Health. Baptist Health is there to support you in your wellness journey wherever it may take you. They really are so much more than a healthcare provider. They're a true partner coming alongside you to help you live your fullest, healthiest life. From pediatrics to women's health to cardiac care to orthopedics to primary care, they offer the full spectrum of services you need to keep yourself and your whole family healthy, no matter what phase of life you're in. And you can always count on the care you receive at Baptist Health to be exceptional and compassionate. Listen, they're Arkansas's most trusted name in healthcare for a reason. For more than a century, Baptist Health has helped countless Arkansans create the healthy lives they deserve. And I know they can do the same for you. I know from experience the level of commitment they have for their patients. I've been a Baptist Health patient for decades, and I'm always in good hands. Their level of care is exceptional. Remember, life isn't just about living. It's about living well, and no one understands that better than Baptist Health. Ready to take the next step in your wellness journey? Visit Baptist-Health.com. Baptist Health, for you, for life.
The king of Arkansas sports talk, Randy Rainwater, for Bet Saracen.
In Arkansas, 7 out of every $10 placed on a sporting bet app is with Bet Saracen, because Bet Saracen offers more ways to win and more ways to get paid and faster. Find your winners on Bet Saracen and look for my double R prop bet specials. I pick them and you win them.
Bet Saracen is Arkansas's favorite sports wagering app.
Gambling problem? Call 800-522-4700.
It's the Ranger Open House Sale through Monday at Bradford Marine and ATV at all six statewide locations. Blast to the boat show deals, like the Ranger 520R with 250 horsepower Mercury with trailer and up to a $2,000 Bass Pro gift card and discounts up to $10,000 on select models. Or check out the SunTracker Sportfish 22, great for fishing and cruising with 115 horsepower Mercury outboard. Don't miss the Open House Sale today through April 1st at all Bradford Marine and ATV statewide locations. Your authorized Ranger and Tracker dealer.
Hello, Buzz listeners. It's Chris Zender, and it's the end of the month, and Fletcher Dodge needs to sell 25 new vehicles before Monday night. We've got 0% financing on new Rams for 72 months, or you can take up to $12,000 off the sticker. It's your choice. This ends Monday night, so give us a chance to show you how great 0% is. We also have new 2024 Jeep Compass four-wheel drives for only $424 a month with zero down and no gimmicks. For you heavy-duty truck owners, we also have brand new 2024 Ram 2500 Crew Cab four-wheel drives priced to sell starting at $49,997. We'll do whatever it takes to make you a deal between now and Monday night, so come see us today. Don't worry about your credit. At Fletcher Dodge, you always get the best price, the lowest finance rate, and more for your trade, and also a hassle-free buying experience. Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Come see us in person at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood, or shop online at FletcherDeals.com. We also have free delivery to your house or work.
Connor has cash. Once again, Connor has cash at the Pickles Gap Weapon Shack in Conway. Connor will buy your used weapon, or he will buy your entire collection. Once again, Connor has cash, and he wants to buy your used weapons at the Pickles Gap Weapon Shack, Highway 65 North in Conway.
Mark Norman, you don't say, Tor.
Hate the small talk. Two things I can't do, small talk and eye contact. How sad is that, you know? I basically have all the traits of a serial killer, just without the ambition. I'm working on it. People always say, Mark, gotta be more confident. They say, Mark, gotta be yourself. I'm like, well, you gotta pick one.
Fresh off his Netflix special, Soup to Nuts, see Mark Norman live on stage this Saturday at Robinson Center. Get tickets now at Ticketmaster.com.
Rock and roll sushi. Deliciously twisted flavors and a rock and roll vibe that'll blow your mind. Try our made-from-scratch hibachi menu. Chicken, shrimp, filet, or lobster with grilled vegetables and fried rice. RockandRollSushi.com.
Now with 5 locations in Central Arkansas.
Welcome back to Morning Mayhem.
Defense on me!
Live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios.
I don't want them to gain another yard.
Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
You blitz all
blitz
night.
Here is David Basil, Roger Scott, and Justin Moore.
Leave no doubt.
A man of many talents, play-by-play broadcaster, real estate agent, and now state legislator. It's time to talk all things Arkansas with R.J. Hawk, presented by Natural State Wholesale, proudly trusted by major manufacturers all over the world for 25 years. Go see the flooring king, Don Gresham, at Natural State Wholesale.
All right. Good morning, RJ. How are you?
What up, guys? How are you?
You have to get to follow the legend, Craig
yes.
O'Neill.
You know what? I don't have a day. I just float. And yeah. So for 2 weeks in a row, we follow the legend.
You're like a designated hitter. You just
put you in
right.
any. You need a segment
perfectly.
You know what? You need a segment filled. Call RJ. Well, he'll get it done.
Somebody, I was looking at our Southern Structural Solutions text line. Yeah. Somebody says Craig was getting down on more middle fingers. He was.
Oh, he's great song. Writing more stuff. He's singing it right now with his shirt, and he's waving his shirt around.
Of course, people are also sending us different songs, quirky song names. So we'll go over those here in just a minute.
Yeah, bless you
very much,
Robert.
Pollen. Yeah, that Craig is something. He is a he's still got it. You know, he's still.
Still.
He told me
in
the break that during COVID he memorized the entire legislature by district and name.
Did you know that, yeah. Justin? He told us this, I think, the first time we had him on.
Because he said he was at home a lot.
Yeah.
And so he said that what he would do was, to keep his memory sharp, he went through and memorized every legislator, both in the House and the Senate, and the district that they're in. And he'd start at one and go one, two, three. You know, I mean, that's pretty impressive.
I am I'm embarrassed to say this.
You only know me in the legislature.
Last night, one of the questions I missed with Ross, and Justin, you may be surprised by this too. I used to love baseball when I was a kid. And I was pretty good in baseball as in football, but I decided, hey, I was going to focus more on football. So last
this might have been one where Josh could have helped you.
Josh would have got this one. I'm very disappointed in myself.
Here we go.
You said
a baseball scorecard.
The baseball scorecard.
What position does the number 6 represent?
Shortstop.
Well, I
what did you say?
I went third.
Huh?
Yeah, because you have success. You have an order that you go from 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, the answer's shortstop.
Yeah, and I picked third. No. I picked.
Did you give multiple choice?
No. It was it was shortstop, and I picked third. Is what I picked, right? Yeah, and so anyway, yeah, I missed that.
How'd you miss that?
Well, I haven't really thought about it in 30 years, and I guess
but
I just
right. sports. Guy.
Listen,
I know.
As soon as I asked that question, I was over
why?
There
that's
by
like, that's
so like saying your ABCs.
So
you should
why,
know that.
Why did they do but, that?
Okay, what? Heard it, I'm sure during games you heard 6-4.
But
three,
why
five,
did they?
Four,
why did they do the numbering the way they did it? Why did they? If you go in the order, pitcher, catcher, first, second,
because the shortstop, because third base, second base, first base, right? The shortstop's kind of an outlier because they're not like assigned to a base.
No, yeah. But he's saying, like, why did they put the number five for third base? I don't know.
Because you're saying, because he's, I'm just saying,
I don't know why.
Where did that come from?
I don't know.
Yeah, they basically skip shortstop. Yeah. Go to third base and then go back.
Yeah, that's why I didn't, you know, again.
It really is kind of.
I bet you if
silly,
we Google it, it'll probably. I have no idea.
Okay, Baz, what is the battery?
The battery. I do not know.
RJ knows this. Come on, you know this.
Battery, come on, you know it.
Battery. Pitcher, catcher.
There you go, bro.
Yes, there you go.
That, listen, the kid, Roger, the kids today, they've got all kind of new terms that we go into back in the 60s.
They've been saying battery.
That is not a new term. Roger, they said that was Babe Ruth.
They just started it in the 90s.
A battery has always been.
No one's ever used it.
Google it.
No one's ever done it.
Babe Ruth just called and he said he used that.
Yeah, they use that with Babe Ruth.
Roger,
battery has
never been used.
I'm with Roger. I'm with Roger.
It's got to be in girls' song.
Just because you don't know it, I love
it. It does have something to do with it.
Nothing on the show ever changes, because if Basil and Roger don't know it, it never happened.
No,
yeah, that's how it is, RJ. Well, but
my
question
RJ,
is, it's 7-8-9 in the outfield, right? It's left field 7, yes. Center's 8.
Yeah, so it's
weird. It kind of goes in the snake. Right?
That, yeah,
one
I just
to two, three, then 3, 4, 5 is left to right.
And what is something known as that. Lamp?
So I did miss that yesterday. Did you,
speaking of which,
I love Lamp.
Speaking of which, Justin, last night the Arkansas Express softball team got their seasons kicked off.
What do you say? What do you know?
Opened up with a 15-4 win last night over Ambush.
Nice.
And
Ambush.
We got it done last night, boy.
Okay,
Little Addie was she was on fire.
Nice. South's team opened up last night with an 11-2 loss.
Oh.
So we did not get off to a great start.
So now is the time when every parent who has a child who's playing ball, it's on now.
It's game on.
Everybody's playing at the same time.
Whether you're playing rec league, tournament folks have been playing for a little while now, but if you're playing rec league tournaments, I mean, everybody's going right now.
Well,
RJ's team and my team are playing in the same tournament.
He told me that
Saturday.
But they moved him.
We're at two different locations because we could have hung out.
What's crazy, Roger?
I actually tried to like, you know how Justin rolls up with the bus whenever he does. So I rented a bus because we got a tournament in Bryant, and so I was like, you know what? I'm not gonna let Justin out bus me. And we were gonna park beside each other, and I was gonna let his people let me on his bus and my people on my bus. Then he's not coming.
Well, what's crazy is, you know, Roger, you know, think about this, like Justin, you know, Ella, who's gonna be obviously she's an outstanding player. She's playing school ball during the week.
Yeah.
And then she does travel ball on the weekend.
Got to get better.
I'm telling you, these kids
mostly
are
out of state.
Yeah, and out of state. It's just but listen, if you can afford it and you have the time to do it. I mean, it's better than the kid doing nothing, but it's a lot of time and effort and money and all the things. And but, boy, it's all on, because if you got a kid, he or she is doing something.
So I'll give you Ella's and I don't make her do this, by the way. She just loves softball. She could care less about basketball or anything else. She loves softball. So Mondays she has private lessons. Practices Thursday and Saturday, and if they don't practice Saturday, it's because they have a tournament on Saturday. So I mean, three or 4 days a week, she's nothing but softball. And when she comes home, she'll go, "Dad, can we go hit?"
Yeah, Edison's the same way.
Well, the other thing about that is that, you know, you're usually going to get better when you're playing that much. You become, but it's a lot of. And the other thing, one thing about Ella. You know, for some kids, you spend that much time, you don't get enough studying done. But you know, she's got great grades, so you've got the school issue. You still got to make sure your kids are doing well in school, which is not easy to do as well because you're spending that much time playing. So
with her, we've never had to worry about that,
which is outstanding.
Some of our other kids, we have to kind of stay on top of it a little bit more. But with her, we've been lucky.
I got to get Addison over to see Ella play.
Addison. Is with the school stuff, but
let's get line one, Roger, real quick. I think somebody's wanting to tell us something. Josh, good morning.
Hey, good morning.
Yes.
I was just I was just calling in to say the battery term in baseball has been around since the 1860s.
Yeah, thank you.
Sir, I'm
thank
sorry,
you.
Josh.
Thank you, Josh.
You're talking about the battery that goes in a flashlight,
sorry,
sir. That's
sir.
What you're talking about.
Josh, can we get him a prize?
And I do want to say Justin Moore. I also say Vianney Wayne.
Thank you. Thank you.
Way to comment. Well, guess what, sir? You're not getting backstage passes. And RJ's not going to have somebody come over there and pave your street for your bogus call.
RJ, was that a great caller or what?
We should have gotten him a prize.
Yeah, he's talking about the battery that Benjamin Franklin created.
He's talking about being on third base, holding a 9-volt battery, and putting the tip of your tongue in between them to get a shot.
This is Wikipedia. They used the term battery was first coined by Henry Chadwick in the 1860s. In reference to the firepower of a team's pitching staff,
thank
inspired
you.
By the artillery batteries.
That's AI Wikipedia, by the way.
In the American Civil War.
It can be
War.
Manipulated, Josh.
Okay. In the American Civil War.
Okay, so here's the
thank
deal.
Thank you, Kate Moore.
I want you to listen to a ball game this year and find it when
never
somebody says battery.
Phil, say it all the time.
It's in the paper. It's in the paper after every game.
Find it.
And the only time you'll hear it is when Joe Buck goes outside and says, I can't start my car. The battery's dead.
When I called Richmond game, games, we had a brother pitched and a brother caught. And I always said the brother battery.
Yeah. The brother battery.
That's really weird.
No one's ever heard that.
It's in the paper after every game.
Never.
Well,
never. Not in the Hot Springs Sentinel Record, mister.
This is what's happened to baseball.
And that's, if you listen
this
to
this is
Phil
what's
Elson.
Happened to baseball. It was almost 200 years ago it started. This is what's happened.
Someone says here, Justin, you know, don't forget, you've got music fans in Texas.
Yeah, bro.
So what do you say for that you
different? Yeah, Justin, what do you say about your fans in Texas?
Batteries at you.
So what?
But you're talking about
I still hate the Longhorns. What do I care?
It's two different things. You don't hate Texas people.
Look,
you hate the Longhorns.
He don't know.
Hey,
listen, Mister.
Hey, Justin, I just bought George Strait tickets at Kyle Field.
I can't believe you of all people as much as you hate that place.
I hate that place, but you know what? He's never played a concert at Kyle Field.
Hey.
And they're expecting
for good reason.
I ain't doing,
they're expecting 130,000 people at Kyle Field.
Wow.
And listen, we thought this was the last, you know, Cowboy Stadium was the last goodbye or whatever.
First
it is.
Off, I listened to you guys, you jacket. The other day, whenever you were bagging on George Strait.
No, you go,
oh, George coming back and just bleeding his fans.
Oh, he is. He's
no,
doing that.
He got hired. He got hired. He got hired by Texas
A&M. He's a sucker.
Because they're having to pay Jimbo all this money to leave.
He said, goodbye, everybody. Thank you for all your support.
And George,
he's the only person who's ever done that.
No, he's not.
The Stones have never done it.
No, but I thought George was above that.
And you know what? George lives 45 minutes from College Station. So, I mean, it works out.
Yeah, well, listen, he just told us it was his last, and I took his word for it.
That's what he did.
But I thought he was different than
George
the Stones.
George Strait fans are suckers.
And I'll say this, Justin. Part of the big reason why we're going is, so my mom lives in College Station now, and built-in babysitter. We can go see the concert.
That stadium holds a ton of people, and if you, it's at least 110,000, and they're gonna, I guess they let them on the field,
whatever.
Too.
Yeah.
That's more than Jerry's World.
So they'll have the entire...
Write this down. Take a little note. I can do the whole thing for you right
there.
They're going to have the whole stadium, and then I think there's like 10 floor sections.
Yeah,
that they're doing.
Listen, the guy's making gazillions. I'm just saying, like you said, Justin, everybody does it. But I just thought maybe he might be different.
I guarantee you, Elvis, if he was still alive, he'd be doing a comeback tour.
He is alive. He's preaching and bitten, you bastard.
Let's go to line one. We got to play Family Feud.
Oh, hey, by the way, this call right here is an awesome call.
I was about to say, is this official here?
This is official right now.
Okay, nobody told me this was going
to
be official.
I know. I meant to tell you this.
All right, Justin, pay attention. JM. Steve, good morning. What Steve is this? Good morning, Steve.
Steve Rook?
Hey. Yeah, this is Steve Rook with ASU Three Rivers. How are y'all doing?
We're doing good. What's going on, man?
Well, I just want to call and make the official announcement. Our ASU Three Rivers Board of Visitors made the recommendation to the ASU System Board of Trustees, and the Board of Trustees passed unanimously to award Justin Moore an honorary associate of applied science from ASU Three Rivers.
There he is.
How about that? Got you a degree there, big boy. Boom. Just like that.
Huh?
Well, that's very kind of you guys. Thank you so much. That's awesome.
Sure.
2 weeks of college has finally turned into a degree.
Steve, hey, Steve, tell us what happens, because Randy Rainwater, is also, this happened with the Little Rock UAR.
How can I turn that into a doctorate?
Well, what we'd like to do is have Justin our graduation in Hot Springs in May. And we can award it then, or we can work out something with y'all and award it to him.
No, no, you got to walk.
I think we'd
love to have him at our graduation.
You got to walk. You got to walk.
We can work out something. And I.
No.
Oh no!
What happened? Call back, Steve.
I think we did work the date out.
Listen, here's the deal. I regret that I did not walk. I regret it.
You didn't walk.
I did not walk.
My mom made me walk.
Yeah, I should have.
I regret that I flunked out of college.
Well, no, you did the right thing for you, Justin. That's right. You did the right thing for you. I think it's great that, again, we've seen, Justin, that some people don't go to school one day and get an honorary degree. They do that.
The person in Jersey that just won $1.1 billion didn't finish their college either.
Yeah, so that'll be cool. Steve Rook is the chancellor at ASU Three Rivers. So what's the date again on the graduation?
It is May 14th at Hot Springs at Bank OZK Arena.
What day of the week is that? A Friday?
That's a Tuesday.
All right. So here's the deal, Roger. We have to be at two graduations. We got to be at Justin's and Double R's, and we got to cheer loud. They say you're not supposed to do that. We're going to cheer.
And I'll come to both and be like, that's my homeboy.
Well, that's outstanding, Steve.
No,
thank
I'll
you.
Be there. Yeah. I'll be there. Thank you guys so much, well, Steve. That's very kind of
tassel. Who's everybody was tassel over?
Yeah, we're having to do that too on his cowboy hat. But he has certainly earned the degree because of his music success, but also because of everything that he's done for the community and raising dollars for great charities and just a great part of our community.
I think the only one additional thing you need to do, Steve, is maybe find one of the classrooms that Justin did grace and maybe put a plaque in there, or maybe in
like
the
hanging on the door. Maybe put
a piece Justin took a class here. Yeah.
Put some tile on.
One time.
Yes.
Or the new baseball facility they have. It can be Justin Moore Field.
What's that going to cost him, Steve?
We'll have to talk about that off air.
All right. We'll get that number. We'll get that check out there.
Well, thanks, Steve. Thanks for calling in and doing
that
on air. That's outstanding.
Thank
you very much. There it is right there. Way to go, college grad.
Very good. How about that? You and Double A. We need to all go out and celebrate. Double R and
party. It is great. You'll have tenure like me.
Double R, you've changed the name of the college, right?
It is UALRR University.
If you keep at this radio thing, you'll be in the Arkansas Sports Hall of Fame, like myself.
Is like care. She's going to have fun with the tassel.
She's going to have fun with the tassel.
helicopter.
Josh, did you did walk, correct? Did you walk?
I did. I got lucky. I graduated when I did, December of 19, because if I had graduated one semester later on.
Oh, those people did not get a chance. High school too, right? High school and college.
I had friends who had to go back to, from the East Coast and from all over the country who had to go back to Missouri like a year and a half later.
So they did let them walk a year later.
Eventually, some of them didn't go back though. Some of them were already working jobs and didn't want to take PTO to go and walk.
But high school. Right, high school did not get the chance to walk. Right during COVID, you did not get.
I don't think so. No.
Yeah, and I hate that. Yeah, I hate that. They didn't get a chance to finish.
They didn't get to go to prom.
No, that's right. That's right.
I didn't go to prom.
Well, you chose not to go to prom.
But you couldn't get a day.
There's that.
That's not true.
Roger, we need to get a contestant, please. I tell you what, let's go ahead. It's 8:20. We're running late here. I tell you what, let's do match game first. Let's throw out match game. Can you find that, Roger?
It's time to play the match game. Brought to you by Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse, Arkansas's truck accessory headquarters for over 30 years. Call 501-568-0040 today or check online at arkansastruck.com. Now, let's see what wacky answers the guys can come up with.
One pair of tickets left to go see Arkansas play LSU.
Oh, boy. What day?
Thursday.
What is today?
That's what Chuck said.
That's tomorrow.
That email, Roger, we got. Chuck said we only have one pair left for Thursday.
So that's tomorrow. Listen, the atmosphere will be outstanding. LSU versus Arkansas, two tickets, 661-1037. All you got to do is just get one of them right. You're in like Flint. 661-1037, isn't it?
In like Flint.
And we also have to...
That goes back to...
1860.
Bingo.
The longest battery has been around.
They didn't even have batteries in 1860. How did they know to use it?
All right, we got a couple. We also too, we got to play Family Feud. So, Representative Hulk, if you can participate in that,
I would love to take. You know what? Match Game is probably one of my most favorite games on this show.
I'm not sure John Mark can play.
Why?
Because he may have won in 60 days. John Mark, have you won in the last 30 days?
That's what I was telling Josh. I think
I'll give you a bag of Hornet ice.
John Mark, go get a bag of ice. Who's this? Hello, caller.
We actually follow those rules, huh?
Who is this?
We do now.
My name's Josh.
Josh?
Yep.
Josh, so you're making that up, aren't you?
It's my proxy.
Josh, you ready to play?
Let's do it.
All right, good luck. And talk into your phone.
All right. Okay. Oh, my gosh. Just Bill Lawrence's 80th birthday today.
Happy birthday, Bill Lawrence.
Oh, my gosh. Little Bill. All right. You go in a lot of different directions here. Holy blank.
Holy blank.
Holy
Holy.
Holy blank.
Now, can we use it, have to spell it a certain way, or can we use it in any way we want? Because there's holy, and then there's holy.
H-O-L-Y. So give us a chance, Josh, for
Got
us
the
to...
the dumb button ready?
Let us think of our... Unless he just said his answer already. Did he already say his answer?
I didn't hear it.
Okay.
I didn't hear it.
You did, Josh?
Well, you can't play.
Justin?
Yes, I can.
I'm good.
Okay. Well, how can you play?
Because I thought of something different. Than
okay, you're going to say you've got the wrong answer. All right, we'll start with RJ. What did you have, Roger?
I went Holy Bible.
Holy Bible. This is going to be a tough one.
Yeah.
Josh, what did you have?
I had Holy Toledo.
Yes.
And Holy Wednesday, which we've made up.
Holy Wednesday.
Holy Wednesday that we made up. Justin, what did you have?
Holy cow.
Holy cow.
Holy cow.
Holy cow.
Roger.
I went in that same way, but I went with my go-to, and that is holy moly.
Holy moly.
Holy moly.
And I went Holy Trinity.
What did the caller get?
Yeah, what did he say?
Josh, what did you say?
No, the caller.
The caller.
Yeah, what did you say, Josh?
I said holy moly.
Holy moly.
So he matched Roger.
Is that what you got?
Out of order. We completely
That's okay. He's going to LSU, Arkansas.
But Josh is honest, so he got it.
Good job, Josh.
Way to go. Hold on. Let Josh Neighbors get all your information.
Boom. Just like that. Do want to thank Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse. Chris and Donnie, appreciate them sponsoring this.
Yes,
thank you,
guys.
You've probably taken your truck over there before.
I actually was there about 2 or 3 months ago, actually, because I had to get a new bed cover.
Also, yesterday, Drew Glover from Natural State Wholesale. Yeah, he called in yesterday. We were talking about about players in NIL, and he was saying his wife, you know, barely makes 50, and she's got a master's degree in teaching school. And she goes, yesterday, Trey Biddy came out and said that every player on the Razorbacks gets $40,000 at the least.
Yeah.
He was just making that. Isn't that amazing?
Great time to live in it.
A teacher can do that. Did you hear yesterday about the two commitments that we lost, the highest rated guy already? They committed in February. Yeah. They've already decommitted.
And because of NIL,
didn't say.
Most likely.
I'm almost thinking now you don't even need to have. What did we do early commitments? Stop the early commitments. It's a waste of time.
The commitments, but the early signing.
I'm talking about early commitment. Just stop. Of course, you know what? If you sign, it doesn't matter, right? You just leave, right?
Well, once you sign, you're bound by that.
How long?
Because the school for 1 year. The school has to release.
Not
you.
Not really.
Well, yeah.
You can get out of it. You can say
you're not going and leave.
Yes and no. I mean, like the kid at Florida. Remember him last? I guess it was last year, the year before. He had signed and he was waiting on Florida to release him because his NIL deal was not what they said it was. And so he's like, I don't want to be here. And they had to release him from his.
Well, Mikel Mitchell, right? They let him from Arkansas in 1 year ago.
All those deals are only 1 year deals. Like, just because you get a scholarship is not a 4-year scholarship.
That's right. It's a scholarship
for 1 year at a time.
I just think it's a waste of time now. Early commitments don't make any. I mean, especially now.
Yeah.
Because there's so much time for a school to come back in there, we're going to offer you more money.
Yeah.
And all you do is get all excited, and all of a sudden, we're 1 month after getting that commitment, and he's already said,
You know what? Just watch pro sports. Then you don't have to have so much heart at it.
The parents.
There's a lot to that, Justin.
Well, listen, The parents are making money too. They're parents that are involved in this.
By the way, if you would
be
better.
By the way, if you would like to do an NIL deal for the Arkansas Express softball team, Six Shoe out in Bryant, we would take your money today. All those little girls could use some lollipops after the game.
Tribe needs some sponsors.
Somebody,
anybody wants to sponsor Tribe 12U?
Somebody says, Bowser, you've got to stand up at Justin's graduation and say, "You're my boy, Blue."
You do. That would be awesome.
There's some parents.
Josh's parents. Hey, finally Josh. Calling back. What's up?
Hey, Josh. I know you're going to be all alone this week. Your mother and I have a crab boil, but we sent you some turkey-flavored ramen noodles to hold you over, you loser.
All right,
we
got to play Family Feud. Yes, Family Feud when we come back, too. We need a contestant.
Brought to you by Floyd Seafood, Keel Avenue in Sherwood. It's crawfish season, and Floyd's has live Louisiana crawfish. Order by 1 p.m. Thursday for weekend boils. Floyd's, meatandseafood.com.
This is SportsCenter.
Arkansas Razorbacks baseball cruised to an 11-0 win yesterday over in-state rival Little Rock. Ben Bibee, Dylan Carter, Christian Fouch, and Stone Hewitt combined to throw seven innings of shutout baseball. Bibee struck out five of the 10 batters that he faced, and on the day, Vahiva Aloy, the shortstop for the Hogs, drove in four runs as well. The Hogs are now 20-3 overall. They host number 8 LSU this weekend in a Thursday, Friday, Saturday series. First game is 6 p.m. on Thursday. Second game is 7 o'clock. On Friday. The series finale is at 2 p.m. on Saturday afternoon. Arkansas softball had their game against UCA canceled due to cold temperatures. I'm Josh Neighbors for the Buzz Radio Network.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Another sunny but cool day with a high of just 62 degrees. Not as windy as yesterday, though, and tonight's low will drop back down to about 39. A little warmer tomorrow at 68 and low 70s back by Friday. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
What's up, everyone? It's Christian Weaver for The Zone. It's going to be a loaded show on Wednesday. Joe Quine will be in studio talking about March Madness. We'll have Hagen Smith on, thanks to Stifel Financial, to preview the LSU series. Kevin Kelly will come on in the second hour, thanks to the Little Rock Athletic Club. We'll talk about the new NFL changes between the kickoff and no more hip drop tackles. Michael Felder will come on in the second hour as well. We'll have comedian Mark Norman call us in the third hour, and Little Rock Trojans wrestling head coach Neil Urshman will join us in the third hour as well. It's all that and much more Wednesday in The Zone, where sports and entertainment come crashing together.
Roger Scott for Sanders Ground Essentials. And if I got some exciting news for you homeowners out there. You see, the Sanders fellas, Kent and Kyle, have been taking care of my lawn for quite some time now. And let me tell you this. If you see their yard sign in your neighborhood, chances are it's boasting the best-looking lawn around. Now, folks, if you're in Central Arkansas, listen up. It's time to get ahead of the game and have Sanders Ground Essentials come out to your house. Why? Because they're ready to apply the pre-emergent spray before that warm weather hits. I know what you're thinking. Winter's still on the calendar, but your lawn is already waking up, and it's hungry, and it needs some feeding. And who better to feed it than Sanders with their top-notch weed and fertilization program? Sanders Ground Essentials is local. Kyle and Kent built this business from the ground up over 20 years ago, and every penny you spend with them stays right here, supporting local employees instead of lining the pockets of some of those big out-of-state corporations. So let's make your yard the talk of the town. Call my friends at Sanders Ground Essentials today at 501-315-9395 or visit them online at sandersground.com. Sanders Ground Essentials. Let's get growing.
Quality Outdoor Products in Alexander, your metal roofing superstore, has a brand new showroom. Take exit 126 off I-30 and visit with Cal about a new carport or metal building. 40-year colors are available at only $289 a foot. 20-year colors are $259 and Galvalume runs $249. Trim and accessories are always available. Take exit 126 in Alexander or call Cal at 501-455-0240 about a new carport, metal building, or metal roofing supplies.
This Saturday, one lucky Saracen casino player will win a Corvette Stingray from Guatney Chevrolet.
This new Corvette is the pinnacle of precision, and with 500 horses and 0 to 60 in under 3 seconds, you'll have more speed than you'll ever need. You can win the most powerful production Stingray in history just for playing, but only at the Saracen Casino Resort, and only this Saturday.
Saracen Casino Resort, Vegas, Arkansas style.
Gambling problem? Call 800-522-4700.
Can't listen to the radio? Don't worry. You can catch Morning Mayhem live every day. Just download the 103.7 The Buzz app.
Nobody's saying they don't appreciate what Jenny did.
Well, if all I had to do was cut a hole in a bag, I could have cut it better than
so
this.
Good. What about you, Robert?
Can you see?
Not too good. I mean, if I don't move my head, I can see you pretty good, more or less. But when I start riding, the bag's moving all over, and I'm riding blind.
I just made mine worse. Anybody bring any extra bags?
No, nobody brought an extra bag. Oh, y'all, I'm going home. Y'all watch my wife work all day getting 30 bags together for you ungrateful sons of bitches, and all I can hear is criticize.
Okay, I'm confused. Are the bags on or off?
I think we all think the bag was a nice idea.
Nice idea.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But not pointing any fingers, nope. They could have been done better. So how about no bags this time? Next time, we do the bags right, and then we go full regalia.
Wait a minute. I didn't say no bags.
But nobody can see.
So?
So it'd be nice to see.
God, this is a raid. I can't see, you can't. So what? All that matters is can the North Sea. That's a raid.
It's time for everyone's favorite game.
That is one of my favorite Tarantinos.
Sponsored by Southern Bank.
Django Unchained.
Visit bankwithsouthern.com for more information about your lending needs. Now, let's play the feud.
That's right. We got us a good one.
And by the way, I've never seen Django Unchained.
Yeah,
it's a heavy movie. That's a great scene. That's a hilarious scene.
All of Tarantino's movies are heavy. These are some of the ones that I've seen. I don't know about Reservoir Dogs. I don't know Inglourious Basterds. I don't know if that has some funny scenes in it or not. But some of the ones I've seen lately have a little humor.
I don't
humor.
Think I've ever seen a Tarantino movie.
Yeah, you might. You just don't know.
Yeah, because I think I tried to watch that Kill Bill. Did he do Kill Bill?
Yeah, he did Kill Bill.
And
Kill
it was
Bill
awful.
Too.
I was like, this is
not a fan. I've never seen Kill Bill either.
Yeah. They're all quirky.
I started it and I was like, I don't have time for this.
Yeah, they're heavy and push the envelope.
Pulp Fiction's considered his best one. That and Reservoir Dogs to me are his two best.
Oh, he
did
Pulp Fiction.
I did watch.
Did see that.
I did watch. You guys, I think, have all seen it. I watched all the John Wicks this past.
Yes, yeah. Those are so awesome.
The fourth one I was sort of numb to. It's like, man, it's like 8,000.
That one was a little strange.
Yeah, it
first
was weird.
First one was enough for me.
Yeah.
I tried to watch
two,
it.
That's about all I could do.
Nah, I didn't even go to.
Although the third one is when they killed.
I called Amazon.
Three was good.
Called Amazon and said, look, I want my money back on that one.
Yeah, third was okay. Third was Roger. That's the sumo guy they killed in that. Yeah, that was okay.
Was he in four or three? He was in four.
He's in four.
I thought it was three. Wow, that was the only part. No, are you sure?
No.
I don't think so. I think it's three.
I don't think so. I think it is.
All right, so we need a contestant.
We're going to be playing. Now, what we're going to be playing for, Josh, okay, we do have a Morning Mayhem shirt.
Yes.
As long as you are the size of the shirt I have.
A Morning Mayhem t-shirt for the winner.
You either get your choice of Mark Norman tickets.
Mark Norman is dubbed by Jerry Seinfeld as the best young up-and-coming comic. He's quickly becoming one of the most talked-about touring comedians on the scene.
Or Avett Brothers tickets.
Or the Avett Brothers. You can go look them up as well.
Now, RJ, just so you know, usually we have Chuck Gatlin in your seat.
Did he not show today?
Justin has not lost a round of Family Feud. And how long, Justin? How long has it been?
Oh, I don't.
6 months? A year?
I don't know.
Maybe a year. A year he has not lost.
He don't lose.
Well, clearly
he's
a college
grad.
Clearly, you guys don't remember my time on the show because I left with a 10-game winning streak with this game. You and I were partnered together, and you clearly don't remember that.
Well, since you've been gone, Justin has had the hot hand.
Well, let's go. Me and Justin.
Yeah, it's you and Justin. Yeah, me
okay,
and Justin.
Okay, let's go.
All right, I think we got David on the line. Roger, go ahead and punch him up, please.
David, are you there?
Yes.
No one's saying you can't. Well, I'm sorry. I'm going back to Django Unchained. All right, David, here's the deal. You have to use your buzzer on this very first question. It's the only time you're going to use that. Your name is your buzzer. Please pay attention to the most recent college graduate of the show Morning Mayhem and listen to his buzzer, if you would please, college grad.
Justin!
David, did you hear that?
Yes.
Let me hear your buzzer.
Justin.
Yeah, you use Justin's buzzer. That's okay. You know what?
Just say David.
That's it. You know what? He just did the classic comedy scene, repeat after me. And he went, repeat after me. Very good. All right, here's the deal. Top five answers are on the board. As I was leaving Mainline Sports Bar last week at Oaklawn, Arkansas's only casino resort, where you will see the only Arkansas Derby this weekend, I asked 100 people this question, and the top five answers were on the board. Now, I just lost my sheet. Hold on a second. Where'd it go? Hold on. My computer just screwed up here. Hold on. Here we go. Let me find it. Uh-oh. I got to go back. Yeah, it just my computer just went blank. I don't know what happened. Hold on. Let me see if I...
I do want to thank the Southern Bank and Chris Roberts for sponsoring this segment. They've done that for a long, long time.
Another Cabot guy. And
And, of course, he banks with Don Grisham banks with him.
I was about to say, Natural State Wholesale and so this little sponsor collusion.
Yes.
And, Chris Roberts and those folks, if you need any banking needs up in Cabot, or really if it's a commercial loan, you're doing a building project, call Chris today. He'll get you done. They service the entire state of Arkansas.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? The teams are David Basil and Joshua Moore against our caller, the
Joshua
King.
Moore.
What'd I say? Joshua Moore. Moore. Just Josh the Neighbors. David, you are the leader of your team, which consists of RJ Hawk and Justin Moore.
Also known as the winners.
Here's the question. Tell me something you have that has lasted longer than most of your relationships.
David.
Justin. Oh, Justin, I heard Justin first. Justin, please.
Your house.
Number three on
the
board.
That's a good one, Justin.
Number three, but here's the thing. There are two answers better than that one. David, Josh, you can control the board if you give me one of the top two. Tell me something you have that has lasted longer than most of your relationships. The top five answers, 100 people, 10 people said house. What's next?
Josh, you think jewelry? What do you think? I don't know.
No, underwear.
Hold on, Dave. No. It's not your turn.
What do you think?
And that's disgusting.
We're already on the board, Dave.
Yeah. One more time. Sorry. I was cutting something.
It's.
I'm in a bad area. I can't hardly hear.
Pull over.
Raj, would you read the question again?
I'm going to read the question again. Tell me something you have that has lasted longer than most of you.
I love how he goes, I'm in a bad area, and somebody said, pull over.
That was me. That was me. This is more important than driving. This is distracted driving. We don't want that right now. Tell me something that you have that has lasted longer than most of your relationships.
Could be jewelry. It could be
clothes, underwear. Underwear is a good option.
Shoes.
Let's go with jewelry. I like jewelry.
We'll go jewelry.
Number two on the board. Control the board right now.
All right. It's a tough decision, but we're going to pass to David, RJ, and
David. Whose team is RJ on?
He's yours.
He's on with you. On with you. Very good. So you have the top five answers on the board. Number two and number three have been answered.
I'm texting with Justin, by the way, so no, I'm not cheating.
RJ and David. Yes. They said something that I didn't think about before, but I think it's a good answer. They said clothes.
Yeah, that was somebody said underwear, but I was going to go with clothes.
David, you are the team leader. Yeah. You can go with that or override these boys.
Hey, I'm going with RJ. What did RJ say?
Wow.
He said pull over.
I said clothes.
He said clothes.
All right. Well, my first thought was that. I don't know. Let's go close.
Number one on the board is clothes and shoes. Two answers remain. Clothes was number one with 17. 13 people said jewelry. 10 people said house. I need number four and number five for you to get these tickets and a T-shirt, David. Where are you calling us from? I'm sorry to end that sentence with a preposition.
Well, I'm in between. I'm in Des Arc.
Do you come to Little Rock often?
Yes.
Okay, good, because we'll have a shirt for you and plus one of these tickets.
Oh, I thought we was playing for the tickets, the Razorback tickets.
Okay, no. Now, you want to hang up now?
Go ahead. Come on, David.
No.
Okay.
No.
All right, so you don't get a shirt either.
I need a free T-shirt.
Okay.
There you go.
All right. Well, so something that Justin and I were going
tell
back
me
and
something
forth on.
That have
y'all need
lasted
to talk instead of
relationships.
Talk instead of text, please.
Well, we don't want to give away any ideas to
no,
you guys.
No, you got to.
What about like a vehicle or an animal, something like that, David?
A vehicle or an animal.
Right, pet or I think an automobile as well, but let's go pet. A lot of people have pets.
Roger goes pet is the answer.
Pet is on the board, but it's not in the top five. Just to let you know, that is one strike against
vehicle,
you.
Then.
Okay, vehicle.
On the board at number four. One answer remains. Two strikes are left. David, the tickets you don't want can be yours if you get the answer. You have two strikes that you can use. While
this
we're talking
is
about
a
it,
hard one.
But please continue on while you're doing that. I want to remind
what
everybody
about
that it's Thursday.
All right, let's go. What about a cell phone? What about your cell phone?
That would be a good one because that lasts longer than a relationship.
Cell phone, Roger. Cell phone.
Let me throw this in there. You change them often.
Your underwear.
I hope that'll. No, I'm saying you change your cell phone.
He's saying the phone.
Oh, I got you. I see what you're saying.
That's a college grad thinking right there.
Oh, like a case or something.
What's that, David?
Speaking of which, I got to go.
I think he's going.
I don't know. I'm stuck on cell
maybe
phone.
Go with cell phone. Go with cell phone, is the answer.
Not even
that's
close.
Two. That's
nobody
two.
Said
one
that.
One more to go.
That's got not
it.
A good one.
All right, here's the deal. One answer remains. You get it right, you get tickets you don't want. You miss it, David and Josh get a chance to steal the tickets you don't want.
What did we say, like, a house?
Yeah, Justin got house number one.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we said that.
What about a relationship?
No, because we're lasting longer than a relationship. That's the question.
Well, and this one, when we say relationship, Justin, I'm going to go ahead and make it known that when we're thinking relationships, we're thinking of a relationship between a man and a woman, and in these days, man and man and woman. We're thinking about a romantic relationship, someone that
or
is
like
tied together.
A friendship.
That is different from a relationship. That's what I want you to know.
Last one.
I like that, Justin.
That's different.
Like what?
But I don't know if it's gonna. Yeah. I like a friendship because I mean
that would be my vote.
All right, David, you want to go with that?
It's totally your call.
Because here's the thing: if we don't get it right, I have like full confidence Baz and Josh aren't gonna get it.
Friendship, Roger, is the answer.
Number five.
Wow. You are a winner, David.
Look, there is a God above.
Also would have been children and job. Children
you,
and
I can't
job.
Tell you, RJ, how many times that Justin has been down to the last strike and he drains of three. Almost every time the last
you know what?
That's
months. Called perfection.
Well, because what it's called is a college grad. You see how he worked his way through that cell phone when he said, well, you get rid of you change your cell phone a lot. Smart move on his part. That's
Josh,
why his
please
wife.
Get David there and get him his
very
prize,
good.
Please.
Congratulations. Tell him to find me. If he wants more than a 2X shirt, he's out of luck. I mean, we'll try to find one.
RJ, too, I want to make mention about your sponsor.
Yeah.
Natural State Wholesale, is that they were able to find this unbelievable hard tile, which
imagine that
yes,
for you.
Yes, they can. Yeah.
How's the hot tub coming along?
It's great. It's wonderful. It's wonderful. I love it.
Have you had the guys over to
not yet.
To swim?
That's coming up. That's coming up.
Have you had the key party yet?
No, we
the what?
Key party.
What's the
going to be a graduation party. We're going to be. We're going to have.
RJ, you don't know what a key party is?
I don't know what a key party
you
is.
You don't? Wow.
What is? I'll let Baz tell you.
I don't know what that is.
Well, you know, key parties have been around since the 1860s.
Exactly.
RJ, come on, man.
I miss that boat. This isn't going to turn into like a Roger Deck party, is it? Where we know nobody.
He said deck.
Oh my gosh.
Where nobody
Roger,
ever got to come over.
We built Roger this deck years ago, Justin. He never invited us over for.
Was a listener then.
Oh yeah, remember that? Never, not once. Like, yeah, we'll do it soon.
Yeah.
He's starting to move.
He got it painted and stained in the
it's
time.
A huge deck, a giant deck. It was
huge
a big deck.
Huge deck.
All right, we'll come back.
He got it painted. What'd you get painted?
Oh, man. His deck.
College grad, Justin Moore. It'll be official on May 14th. Three Rivers.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good stuff. All right, 8:45. Hey, folks, it's David Basil out here at Fletcher Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sherwood. Fletcher Dodge wants to help you lower your car payment. Come on in and let them show you how. It's possible to trade in your old car for a brand new Dodge Chrysler Jeep or Ram with a lower car payment. They've got 0% financing on new Rams, or you can take up to $12,000 off the sticker. Your choice. And how about 0% financing on new Chrysler Pacificas and $10,000 discounts on new Jeep Gladiators? Or how about a new Dodge Charger or Challenger for $5,000 off? Fletcher Dodge has lots of inventory to choose from. They'll do the rest. And don't worry about your credit. If other dealers have told you no, come see us and let us help you get a new vehicle to get you to school or to work. For the best selection, lowest price, and best buying experience, go see my friends at Fletcher Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sherwood, or you can shop online at FletcherDeals.com. Remember, 0% financing on new Rams, or you can take up to $12,000 off the sticker. That's just one of many deals they'll give you over at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
The all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock is now open. Over 100,000 square feet of hardware, outdoor appliances, a window and door center, and even a drive-through lumber yard. And there's nothing like Design One. This stunning showroom is one place for all your home and design needs, including 12 full kitchens and 9 baths, plus a huge selection of lighting, flooring, countertops, and more. At the all-new Lumber One and Design One, now open in West Little Rock.
Clayton Homes of Conway is moving. But until then, you can find them at their location on East Dave Ward Drive, where you're invited to stop by on April 12th and 13th for their inventory reduction sale. Save thousands of dollars on in-stock inventory of homes. Lenders will be available for all your financing questions. There'll be door prizes, food, fun, and entertainment for the whole family. April 12th and 13th at Clayton Homes of Conway.
Right now at Fort Thompson, Smith & Wesson Shield, 2.09 millimeter, $269.90. Beretta APX-A1, 9mm, $199.90 after $50 mail-in rebate. CCI 9mm brass, 50 count box, $12.99 at Fort Thompson and Sherwood.
You know what happens when a smart group of medical professionals get together and commit to a technology designed to relieve your aching joints without surgery? Is call QC Kinetics.
And this guy knows the power of a solid team. Emmett Smith, football legend and Dancing with the Stars champ.
This elite medical group, some of them orthopedic doctors, got together and said, why are we prescribing so many medications? Why are we sending so many people to surgery in droves? Let's change this.
The answer, natural biologics. Our own healing properties. And the outcome is the country's largest provider of non-surgical regenerative treatments, QC Kinetics.
Actually, the real outcome are the tens of thousands of patients who finally got their quality of life back without surgery, thanks to QC Kinetics.
Call QC Kinetics, 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440.
Stop by Hennard Foothills Equipment in Searcy and check out Arkansas's very own Spartan zero-turn mowers manufactured in Batesville. And if you're a fan of quality, look no further. Hennard's carries still handheld equipment. Hennard Foothills Equipment in Searcy, your hometown dealer no matter where you live, 501-268-1987.
Let me tell you about my friends Carl and Karen. This place is sus. Let's go to Tunica.
And so they did. And immediately, they became winners.
Hey, baby, what you doing?
Winning. Hey, baby, what you doing?
Winning.
And not just gaming either. They did spinning, dancing.
Winning.
That's or at the sports
book. Winning.
Or enjoying a world-renowned meal.
Winning.
No matter what you're doing in Tunica, you're always a winner.
Learn more at tunicatravel.com.
It's the Average Guy Movie Review, Thursdays in the Zone with Justin and DJ, presented by Rock and Roll Sushi. The guys will recap or look ahead to what's trending on TV, the big screen, Netflix, or however you receive your TV service. Presented by Rock and Roll Sushi, deliciously twisted flavors and a rock and roll vibe that will blow your mind. Rockandrollsushi.com.
Want to see our beautiful faces? Catch Morning Mayhem streaming live every day on YouTube, X, and Facebook. Just search 1037 The Buzz.
I've heard that quite a bit.
Yeah, what,
quite a bit. Sorry. I don't know what I said.
Get that. Get that. Yes, stumbles. I find joy in your stumbles whenever I can.
Man, when you're laying pipe. Nah.
Mayonnaise. It's mayonnaise.
What in the world?
Mayonnaise. I love that.
All right, here we go. This is for Mrs. Kate. Right here.
When you're laying pie, what did that come from?
I don't know.
When your baby.
And you lay pipe.
Leaves you all
I still
alone.
Can't get over. You know, you guys introduced me to the mayonnaise and or whatever nobody. It was last year. And I went home and told my wife, I said, have you ever heard anybody say that? She's like, I never heard it. I was blown away.
We love Kate for giving us that.
I love Kate, but.
That jewel. Don't you feel like crying? She loves this song, too.
You want your husband to cover it.
Do you want to thank God?
It stinks in here.
It does. It does. Like, open the window.
Do you want to thank Natural State Wholesale for sponsoring RJ and Don Grisham and the boys. They do a great job out there.
They've got a big warehouse.
Yeah, full,
and they got more product than they've ever had. Yeah. And if you're looking for tile, hardwoods, laminates, go by and see Don and the guys over at Natural State Wholesale. You can go online, naturalstatewholesale.com. I promise. In fact, I had a client the other day. He said, man, I don't want to go all the way to Cabot. I said, look, you are going to save way more money than if you go in any big box store around
yes.
here. And so he did. Saved him almost $2,000 compared to where he was at. And so,
shut up!
Just go out
no
there.
No way. Shut up!
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No.
He had a big house.
You
mark the tape,
are
Josh.
Lying!
I'm not lying.
Call
Drew over at Natural State.
A couple of messages here. Hey there, since you were talking about travel ball, I'd like to give a shout-out to my daughter's national volleyball team. They play for 501 Volley in Central Arkansas. Went down to New Orleans this past weekend, won the tournament out of 80 teams.
Nice.
They won
That's
their
awesome.
Bid to play in Nationals in Vegas in July. They went 10-0 against teams from all over the country.
Yeah.
501 Volley, 17.1 national. First team in Arkansas to earn a national bid.
That's awesome.
That's another sport we hadn't even mentioned.
Yeah.
That's travel.
You know, Chris Walker's got a big volleyball league.
Very passionate about that.
Yeah, and they're doing great things down there.
Big fan of Chris Walker.
By the way, and this weekend, there's a big tournament in Saline County. If you're into softball and, you know, 6U to, what is it, Justin, 14U, being played between Malvern and Bryant this weekend. And there's going to be a lot of folks in the area.
And earlier, RJ, I had heard you say, but I couldn't get a word in edgewise.
Yeah.
Shocker on the show. you need to bring Addison to come see Ella. Man, anytime.
Yeah.
Come on.
I think she'd like that. She likes watching the bigger girls play. And, you know, I tell you what, boy, we watch a lot of Razorback games now. And Addison, you know,
she liked it.
Well, she started, you know, the other day she started mimicking some of what they do at the plate.
Yeah.
And I said, where'd you get that? She goes, well, that's what the Razorbacks do.
Yeah.
And so, you know, it's kind of cool whenever the younger kids can watch the older ones and they pick things up. And
last night.
Go ahead.
I was going to say last night real quick, you know, Arkansas was supposed to play UCA in softball.
Yeah.
They postponed it, I guess, for the weather, even though the guys went ahead and played. So I'm almost glad because, you know, I hated that both were on the same night that they're in Fayetteville.
Right.
So hopefully that'll give another chance for Razorback fans or UCA fans to get up there and watch
that game. UCA won last year.
I remember that. Did they beat them twice? I think they beat them at home and up there,
I think, right? Yeah, beat them twice.
Yeah, it's a good program. Yeah. Go ahead, Justin.
I was just going to say RJ is like me and played baseball, and he played – higher level than I did. He played in college, but isn't it crazy how you learn to love softball even more than baseball?
I'm gonna tell you right now, I was telling him, you know,
it's a faster game.
Yeah. I've got a 2-year-old boy, different. And part of me is like, man, I hope we don't play baseball because like I have really enjoyed the softball game, and
it's fun to watch.
At our level, I don't know if it changes when you get older, but we're 55 minutes now.
Yeah,
I mean,
love it.
You get in, get out. It's fast paced. You roll, and so yeah, man, I love it. Hey, before we hit the break, I wonder.
Yeah.
I'm not trying to pull a Tommy, but April 22nd, it's that legislative basketball game that we talked about just a minute ago.
Benefits.
Boys and girls, not the Boys and Girls Club.
Big Brothers, Big Sisters.
Yeah, Big Brothers, Big Sisters, as well as the Children's Advocacy Centers of Arkansas. It's the legislative game, House versus Senate, but this year. We're adding the governor's team, the attorney general and governor, they're going to have a team, and it's going to be a 3-on-3 half-court tournament style. So
too many injuries last year, Justin.
We had two Achilles go out last year as well as a rotator cuff.
Oh, no.
Yeah, so we went half-court.
We
raised, I think they raised $30,000 for these groups last year.
Yeah,
wow. So April 22nd at Little Rock Central, we're doing it again.
There's a lot of huffing and puffing going on there last year.
I've been running, but I don't have to go full court this year, so I'm good.
Yes. If you want to recruit anybody, I'm not going to play much defense, but I can knock down a spot.
Justin,
he's in. What?
We may get you in there for sure.
Honorary state rep.
Yes. Thanks, RJ.
Yes. See you guys.
9 o'clock.
See you, bud.
Hey, it's David Basil for Simmons Bank. You've heard me say over and over again how much I love being a Simmons Bank customer and learning about their amazing success story, starting with one little Pine Bluff bank in 1903 and now celebrating their 120th banking birthday. They have become one of the fastest growing banks in America. 120 years in banking, that's a ton of experience. The reason Simmons Bank has been around for 12 decades is because they have a track record of helping people turn their goals into plans, and that's worth repeating. Simmons Bank knows how to help their customers turn their goals into plans, and they're ready to talk to you now, but first, they'll listen. Simmons Bank will guide you at every step. No matter what's next in your life, Simmons Bank wants to make financing the easiest decision you make. A personal loan from Simmons Bank could be the solution you need for large purchases like home improvement projects, wedding expenses, vacations, emergency expenses, or an automobile, boat, or RV purchase. Don't wait any longer. Let Simmons Bank help change your financial life.
Mark your calendars for the 20th annual Double B's BuzzBecue, Saturday, May 11th at the downtown Riverside RV Park in North Little Rock. Tickets on sale soon.
More fun and games than an amusement park arcade. 103.7 The Buzz, KABZ Little Rock.
Buzz News with Channel 7's Cassandra Webb.
Little Rock Mayor Frank Scott Jr. is among 21 mayors who will travel to Memphis today, joining the Black Mayors Coalition on Crime and its efforts to reduce violent crime in America's cities. Memphis Mayor Paul Young launched the effort in partnership with the African American Mayors Association. Young took office in Memphis earlier this year and says a high-profile national movement of mayors could help solve ongoing issues with crime. According to a recent Gallup poll, voters' concerns about crime are at their highest level since 2016. Local businesses are stocking their shelves ahead of the total solar eclipse. Edwards Food Giant is preparing for an increased volume of customers looking to buy meat, bread, and other staple items for the eclipse. They plan on getting some trucks ahead of time with all those groceries. Cavanaugh Pharmacy is also getting necessities in case of an emergency. They'll have Band-Aids, Neosporin, antiseptic, and all other health items. Both stores will carry NASA-approved solar eclipse glasses while supplies last. From the Channel 7 Newsroom, I'm Cassandra Webb.
Anywhere in the state, dial 888-888-8888 for Rainwater Holton Sexton. They'll help you weather the storm.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Another sunny but cool day with a high of just 62 degrees. Not as windy as yesterday, though, and tonight's low will drop back down to about 39. Little warmer tomorrow at 68 and low 70s back by Friday. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Want the latest information on bass tournaments and the best fishing spots in the state? Then listen to Fishing Arkansas Sunday mornings with Big Sarge and his crew. Fishing Arkansas is presented by Shelter Insurance Agent Jamie Marsh, Stanley Hardware, Fletcher Auto Group, Axles Plus, and Cooper's Nursery in Cabot. Fishing Arkansas Sunday mornings on 103.7 The Buzz.
Hello there, homeowner. Roger Scott for Leafguard Gutters of Arkansas. Are you tired of dealing with clogged gutters, climbing ladders, and worrying about potential damage to your home? Well, listen up to me now. Leafguard of Arkansas's got you covered. Introducing Leafguard, the only true one-piece seamless covered gutter system on the market guaranteed to never, ever clog. With Leafguard, you can kiss goodbye to all the hassle of climbing up and cleaning out all that muck and mud and shingle grit. No more hiring someone else to do it, or worse yet, risking serious damage and issues by doing nothing at all. Spring is finally here, which means it's time for Leafguard's famous Ugly Gutter Event. LeafGuard will swoop in, take down, and haul away all those unsightly gutters at absolutely no charge, and you'll receive an incredible 60% off installation on a whole house LeafGuard gutter system. But wait, there's more. Ask about the 0% financing options and additional discounts for seniors and military personnel. Do not let ugly gutters ruin your home's curb appeal or cause costly damage. Call 501-664-5400 or visit leafguardandmore.com to schedule your free estimate today. LeafGuard of Arkansas, protecting your home one seamless gutter at a time.
Tackle your outdoor projects with Greenway Equipment's Lawn Patrol Package. Handling is effortless with the John Deere 1023E's Twin Touch Foot Controls with a hydrostatic transmission and four-wheel drive with power steering. The 60D Driveover Auto Connect Belly Mower makes mowing easy. And the 120R Quick Park Loader is perfect for dirt moving and mulching projects. With 0% APR for 84 months and a 6-year powertrain warranty, it's a deal you can't miss. For more information, head to your local Greenway or visit GoGreenway.com. With approved credit, see dealer for details.
Hello, I'm the Easter Bunny.
I know, I sound a lot like Craig O'Neill. I get that a lot. I have a confession to make. You think I'm an Easter tradition? I am nothing compared to a Petit Jean ham for Easter. Surely, after being around for over 95 years using real hickory to smoke their meat, I shouldn't have to remind you to get a Petit Jean ham for Easter. Ooh, Petit Jean. What a great place to go hide eggs. If you'll excuse me, I've got a mountain to climb. And you've got a ham to buy. Petit Jean Meats. Taste the difference.
Red tape. One in three businesses will get caught up in it. And they'll be penalized by the IRS for mismanaging their payroll. Because when you're handling payroll, HR compliance, and those constantly changing tax laws, that red tape can get sticky in a hurry. At The Payroll Company, we free you from that tangled mess and get you back to business. The Payroll Company. Less headaches, more than payroll. Visit morethanpayroll.com to learn more.
It's the Ranger Open House Sale through Monday at Bradford Marine and ATV at all six statewide locations. Blast to the boat show deals, like the Ranger 520R with 250 horsepower Mercury with trailer and up to a $2,000 Bass Pro gift card and discounts up to $10,000 on select models. Or check out the SunTracker Sportfish 22, great for fishing and cruising with 115 horsepower Mercury outboard. Don't miss the Open House Sale today through April 1st at all Bradford Marine and ATV statewide locations. Your authorized Ranger and Tracker dealer.
At ABC Supply, when you've got a job to do, we do too. When your success depends on getting the details right, we're there for you every step of the way. Delivering more than materials, delivering passion, commitment, and the confidence to help you get the job done easier. Our teams understand the obstacles you face in building your business and reputation. Because living up to our promises is how we help you live up to yours.
For location and product information, call ABC Supply North Little Rock at 501-955-0777 or visit abcsupply.com.
Old Man Winter here. One more snowstorm.
Not a chance, Mr. Winter. It's spring.
It's also time for the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event, where you can get great deals on all our award-winning Hyundai models, all backed by America's best warranty. Hurry in. These deals won't last at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Now get 0% APR on the Tucson or pay only $369 a month with zero down payment. Now, during the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Offers end soon. Call 469-613-0227 for details.
Welcome back to Morning Mayhem.
I want your blood. I want your soul.
Live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios.
I want them both right now.
Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
I'm your huckleberry.
Here is David Basil, Roger Scott, and Justin Moore.
All right, Lunger, let's do it.
So good. 9:06 here on Morning Mayhem. Morning Mayhem has fully assembled. I'm David Basil. That's Roger Scott. Justin Moore in Pullen, Arkansas.
Say,
up on Moore Mountain. And Josh Neighbors producing.
Hey, J-Bar, Josh.
Now, Justin, you're, let me, first of all, I'm going to go to my calendar and just see if I have this. Looking at March. March. Your birthday is April 1. What is your exact birthday for number 40, Justin? No, he's 30. March 30th. I see it here. Did we lose Justin? Is he there?
He said Saturday, didn't he?
Yeah, it's, let's see here.
March 30th.
March 30th. That's Saturday. Big 40, what do you, what are the plans that Justin Moore has for number 40?
Well, I tell you.
I think we might, did we lose him?
Oh, dang on, dang on. He's probably asleep.
May be.
Justin!
40, Roger, what do you, I mean, I remember 40 was a big deal.
40 was a big one. What did Sam do for me on my 40? I think she held a party for me out in... at a VFW with Matt Jackson and so many other folks from that era, 40. I think we got 40.
I think 40 was a cool one for me. I think 50 was like, wow, 50 was a shocker.
50 was different. Yeah, I looked down and I saw, you know, a whole lot of stuff.
60 was...
That's when you start looking like the back of those pickup trucks hanging down on that hook.
Anyway, so I want to find out some more details on Justin's 40th birthday, which is on the 30th. The other thing is, good morning, Justin.
He's a college grad now.
He is a college grad now. Oh, there he is. So you were taking care of business.
College grad.
That's what he was going to do. We were talking about your birthday. It's on a Saturday.
Yeah,
on Saturday. So yeah, I was wondering, are you guys having a big big party, big gathering for the Big 40?
No, I'll be coaching a softball tournament.
Boom, boom. I noticed you didn't have any concerts this weekend. I presume that was on purpose so you could celebrate and coach.
No, it was more for Easter.
Oh, that's true. That's true. That's right. You got Easter on Sunday. That's a good point.
I mean, my birthday, I told Kate, I go, please do not do like a 40th surprise party. Yeah, I don't like that stuff. So I'll be in my favorite place, the softball field. Unfortunately, my daughter's team that I'm coaching, she won't get to play because she's got a broken arm.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's too bad.
But I'll be coaching her team.
Well, I was going to ask, we talked about this with what day is it? I can't remember what day it was, Roger. Who were we talking to about wearing? Oh, it was Bill Vickery, because he's an only child. I'm an only child. Justin, you're an only child.
Right.
Did your parents dress you up in the little Easter outfits when you were a little kid?
Oh, yeah, with a bow tie and the whole thing. Yeah.
Yes, did you do that for your girls? I know. I guess you could do it for South.
I don't do anything for their attire.
Yeah,
that's all my wife.
What about South? Did South last year get dressed up in a little outfit?
I think Kate gets him outfits, but it's not like what I wore. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Like, she pretty much dresses him like me, which I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing.
Yes. Yes.
He wears boots and a button down and jeans and, you know.
He looked cute in his little outfit, his uniform last night. All the Moors wear number 10s, like Roger did too.
Yeah.
A couple things I wanted to get to. One sports note, Roger, historically, on this day, 1971, UCLA became the first team to win 5 consecutive NCAA basketball titles. They beat Villanova at 68-62.
That was NIL before NIL.
Probably so. It was John Wooden. Then they came back, and apparently they win? 9? They won 9 in a row, lost 1, and came back and won 10? I think they won 9. I mean, can you imagine 9 national titles in 10 years? Or maybe it was 10 altogether. But anyway, I noticed that was on this date, 71. Also, Janis Joplin, Roger, started her second week and final week at the top of the music charts with Me and Bobby McGee, written by who?
Chris Christopherson.
That's right.
Baton Rouge, waiting for a train, on us feeling near as faded as my jeans.
I like the song.
Bobby thumbed a diesel down just before it rained and rode us all the way into New Orleans. I pulled my harpoon and my dirty red bandana. I was playing soft while Bobby sang the blues. Windshield wiper slapping time, I was holding Bobby's hand in mine.
Come on.
We sang every song that Javi knew.
Who wrote it?
Christopherson.
Just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing. I mean nothing, honey, if it ain't free. No. Feeling good was easy along when he sang the blues. You know, feeling good was good enough for me.
Great dynamic.
Good enough for me and my Bobby McGee.
Oh, yeah. You know, she has
what song do I name check that? What song of mine do I name check that song in?
I know. I know you mentioned it. I know it. I listened to it the other day.
Yeah.
I heard it the other day.
And what was it? Say it!
Because you mentioned some other names. You mentioned some other names in that song, too. It wasn't just there's something else.
Hank.
Yeah.
Senior.
It's not Hankett, is it? No, it's
Hankett.
It's a ballad.
I just heard that the other day because it mentioned you. Like
if
I said,
heaven
you,
wasn't so far.
That's
away.
Right. Yeah, number one hit too.
Come on.
Shameless plug by myself.
It's about time you did it.
Every day I drive to work across
it's in the second
Flint
verse.
River Bridge.
We got time.
We got 45 minutes.
For me and Grandpa Fish.
4-hour show, Jim.
There's a piece of his old fruit stand on the side of Sawmill Road.
Let's see how long how bad the delay is today, Justin. Sing along.
If it was 20 years ago.
All right.
What I wouldn't give
to ride
around in that old truck with him. If heaven wasn't so far away, pack up the kids and go for the day.
Introduce them to their grandpa. Watch them laugh at the way he talk.
Outstanding.
Bad?
Outstanding.
No, not bad at all. You know, that line like that, it, the older I get, the more emotional I get when I think about things like that, you know, with when your parents are gone, they can't, you know, your kids don't get to see them with your grandkids. That's a great, great boy.
In the rearview mirror, we don't watch them wave. Yeah, losing them wouldn't be so hard to take if heaven wasn't so far away. I'd hug all three of those girls we lost from the class of 99. And I'd find my bird dog boat and take him hunting one more time. Ask Hank why he took those pills back in 53. Janice to sing the second verse of me and Bobby McGee.
Boom.
Yeah, there
Boom.
It is.
Boom. There it is. Did you write that, yeah. Justin? Did you get that?
No,
lyric?
Actually, I did not write that. But I to Roger's point about, you know, listening to songs and it takes you to a certain place in time and as you get older. So my grandfather passed away in November, like 12, 13 years ago, and he was my hero. And my daughter was – my oldest daughter, Ella, was born in February, and he couldn't speak because they had given him a tracheotomy.
Mm.
And unnecessarily, by the way.
Ooh.
So the way he communicated, he wrote on a magic marker board, and he wrote on a magic marker board, "Tell Ella I love her."
Oh,
and
that's something.
I'm about to start crying right now. Every time I think about that, I start crying. But so I recorded that. I heard that song right after that happened, and I was like, I got to record this song.
Yeah,
and. So
yeah, it's good stuff. That was I don't know what number one that was for you, but obviously that was a number one for you.
Yeah, I don't know. It was my first single for my second album, so maybe my third.
So
like that.
I may be wrong on this, Raj, and I didn't realize this. I'm just now glancing at it.
Yeah.
Says here that single, "Me and Bobby McGee," became only the second in Billboard's history to vault to the top of the pop chart following the artist's death. Following Otis Redding's 1967,
wow, really?
"Sitting on the Dock of the Bay," I did not know that. If that's the case,
I didn't know she was dead either.
I didn't know that she had recorded it. Just it looks like it says here. It says both. Let's see. It doesn't say exactly. She died on October 4th, 1970. So I didn't know that either. If that's the case, that's I did not know that. So, but that's a great song, I'm sure, for Kristofferson. I mean, that's obviously.
Oh, I've heard him sing it too. I mean, he's got a distinct sound. You know, it's just when you hear some of them sing him, like the Sunday Morning Coming Down.
Yeah,
the way he sings that one.
Yeah, I know some people don't like Janis Joplin's voice, and I know some like Mercedes Benz.
Mercedes Benz doesn't do it.
That's a great song.
That's
there.
That's the one right there. You know, and last night I had a trivia question, Justin. It was who became the very first black woman to have a number one song on the country charts, and what was the name of that song? The first
sort of a trick question.
First black woman. Yeah, that's why. Don't say anything, Bass. The first black woman to have a number one song on the country charts. It just happened recently.
Can you give
recently.
Me the air?
It just happened recently.
Just happened two months ago.
Beyonce.
Yeah.
Well, that's one of them.
See, that's the other deal. And that's the other. So, Bass, once again.
I was playing trivia, and I go, wait a minute.
Right, so he starts pulling out.
So it's not Beyonce?
So, you know, it is. That the answer is Beyonce.
Oh, okay.
I thought.
Well, that's what he's getting ready to say.
Answer is Beyonce and Texas Hold'em. But the caveat here is what Baz brought up. Who was the tight jean guy that did Fast Cars?
Luke Combs.
Luke Combs.
So Luke Combs comes out.
Oh,
and
he
does Fast Cars. But. Yeah. Would you count
Tracy Chapman
as being the first black woman to have a number one on country Billboard?
So what it did, Justin?
I guess it was talking about artists.
See, artists.
Well, so the question is,
a distinction between that, right?
There's two things you got a singer and a writer. It was her song, but she was the first black woman to have a number one song. She didn't sing it. She wrote it though, and so Beyonce was the first singing artist.
But she did sing it. You know what I mean?
But it wasn't number one.
It was not on the country.
But it is interesting. She does have a number one as a writer.
So where do you stand? What do you stand, Jay Bird, on that one? I mean, can you remove yourself from that without saying, hey, if I wrote a song, it was my number one song, if somebody else covered one of your songs that you wrote? So,
still a number one. You know, I mean, yeah, you just didn't sing it yet.
She's thrilled because it's made her a lot of money.
Right? Yes, that's a good point. Roger, 2 years later, I wanted to bring this up. And Justin, I don't know, Josh, I presume you would not have heard of this, but Justin, maybe. So it was Oscar night for the 45th time. Marlon Brando wins the Best Actor Award for his performance in The Godfather. Many consider the greatest movie of all time. But he refused to accept the award because he felt the U.S. and Hollywood were discriminating against American Indians. And so, interesting.
That is not justice. Your daughter is still alive.
So good. So do you know what he did instead?
Didn't he send somebody up in his place?
He did. He sent somebody.
I don't know what to do. You can act like a man!
Johnny Fontaine.
Yeah, listen, we've got to do name the movie lyrics by the Goombas. So he sends out Sachin Littlefeather to the ceremony to refuse the
Oscar.
Are you
talking about last night?
No, the 1973.
Marlon Brando did this for The Godfather.
Yes, and so he sends out this woman, Roger, Sachin Littlefeather, who everybody presumed was a Native American. Turns out she was Mexican. You know, he's protesting about the way the Native Americans are being treated.
Is that right?
And he sends out a Mexican.
She was an activist for Native Americans.
You come to me on the day of my daughter's wedding, and you ask for justice. This is not justice. That is not justice, your daughter.
That is not justice.
That is not justice, you know. That is not justice.
So good.
Another one of those for you. I don't know what to do. You can act like a man!
Johnny Fontaine.
That's who he's talking to.
Yeah, it is.
The singer.
So
he's supposed to be Frank Sinatra, but...
That was so...
You can act like a man!
He was perfect for that. He was perfectly cast for that role. By the way, Roger, her real name was Maria Cruz.
No way.
Yes, he called her Sachin Littlefeather, but her real name was Maria Cruz.
Wow.
Don Corleone.
She was accused of being a pretendian.
Pretendian.
This is in Wikipedia.
Yes. Wow.
Wikipedia says she was accused of being...
When did they find this out? Now, would you not consider... I don't know. All right, help me out on this one now. Because, I mean, are Native Americans Mexican or are Mexicans Native Americans? What's the deal on that one? Because we have like...
I don't think it's either.
There's none of them? Is there Mexican or Indian and Mexican?
You can have Mexican Indians.
You can. That's what I'm saying. So, which Indians were... Because they were in that area.
Pueblo.
In that territory.
Maybe Pueblo.
You got your Pueblo. You got your
Mississauga?
No. I don't know. I'll stop right
Don
there.
Don Corleone.
Speaking of...
I'm honored to be at your daughter's wedding.
Hey, you know the story on that?
On the day of your daughter's wedding.
Justin, you know the story there. He's a real gangster.
He was a real gangster.
Who was that? Luca Brasi, right?
Yes.
Luca Brasi.
He's a real gangster.
You find out about that if you watch that, that show, The Offer... that was based on the making of The Godfather that was on last year or whatever, you find out that Luca Brasi was actually on the Joe Colombo team. I think it was Joe Colombo. You know,
crazy.
Because they were going.
He looks like a mafia dude.
He is a mafia dude.
He looks like a mob
guy. It's surprising they let that movie get made with the mafia.
Don't he end up getting his hand stabbed with a knife? Salazzo, I think, in the bar. I think Salazzo gets him.
What can I do? What is that, Nazi? Ridiculous.
He sleeps with
the
fishes.
He sounds like Jack White doing Elvis. Ridiculous.
You spend time with your family?
Sure I do.
Good. Because a man that doesn't spend time with his family can never be a real man.
Be a real man.
What a great movie.
It's so good.
It still holds up today.
It's so... The casting, the writing.
Driving his family can never be a real man.
Listen, you are in a robe.
So the
I don't even know what you're wearing.
The best part is when he's talking to Michael, he's talking to Al Pacino, and you can tell he's reading the cue cards off his chest.
Well, when you know it
but
now.
It's still so good,
yes.
though. It's still so
when
good.
When you know it now,
that's
you
how
have
he
no
used
idea.
To do it, right? He used to read all the cue cards.
Yes,
it's like us right now. It's
Who
like
did?
Us.
Brando.
Brando had everybody in his scene. Oh, everybody had cue cards
wow.
strapped to their chest.
Not,
you know how painstaking it is to have
ridiculous.
To redo those scenes over and over again.
Because Al Pacino's just got like
this embarrassing.
Like, I never wanted this for you.
I never
strapped
knew
to his
that.
Chest.
Yes.
Robert Duvall as well.
Yeah, Robert Duvall.
All of them.
Yeah,
I mean, they all had yeah. these things strapped.
And many consider Brando the greatest, one of the greatest of all time. But he used to
sure. He had some freak in him though too. He had
he
some freak. You start reading a little bit about him. And James Ballantyne's favorite book about Scotty Bowers.
The other one I wanted to bring up, Roger. It was on this day in '95 that Forrest Gump won the best movie.
Anyway, like I was saying, shrimp is the fruit of the sea. You can barbecue it.
I gotta find Bubba!
Anyway, like I was saying, shrimp is the fruit of the sea.
He won, the movie won, and Tom Hanks won for Best Actor. I sent you the clip yesterday. I should have sent it to Josh and Justin. It shows outtakes of Tom
Hanks. I saw
and so
that.
You can imagine when Tom Hanks comes up with this, and he created this character by watching this little kid who was going to play him.
The one of the kids that played him.
He had the funny accent. He decided to morph that into his adult. Mm-hmm. And the first time everybody's hearing that, they're laughing. Yeah. He's like, because he pulls it off. But just amazing. The other thing they didn't show, they had a scene that they cut out of the movie. Roger, remember which one it was?
I do.
So Justin and Josh, there was a scene where it was Martin Luther King marching.
Yep.
And I don't know where it was. I don't know if it was the Selma Bridge or whatever. But these German shepherds just start coming at him to start biting him. And Tom Hanks' character, Forrest Gump, appears and he's got sticks. He goes, hey. And all the dogs run to Forrest Gump, and he takes him out of the way, throws the stick, and
yeah, that would be a little bit too far because he's in these famous moments, but he's not like involved in them. That would have been like far too involved. In
well, he did tell President Kennedy he had to pee, didn't he? He said, "I'm sorry, Mr. President, I have to go pee there in the White House." I think he
I
said
guess
that.
He did. Did he?
Yeah, he did. I think he did. And but anyway, so it's all these black leaders sitting there. It's almost like Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. It's sort of an alternate ending.
Revisionist history.
Yeah, wouldn't it be amazing if Forrest
Gump. Which is great history, though.
Well, then the other one, you had when Bear Bryant says, "What's that boy's name?" Or whatever.
Yeah,
get
sure
him in the game.
Yes. He's the stupidest son of a.
Yes, it
sure can run. Then he was at college.
Do y'all love
college.
That movie?
I do. I think
I
it's great.
It,
yeah, but. I do. I think it's amazing. I don't watch it all the time, but
yeah,
I think
it's great soundtrack.
Unpopular opinion. I think that movie is overrated.
I do, too.
I like it, but I don't think it's like the greatest movie ever.
It beat
like
out Pulp
people.
Fiction and
that was not justice.
It beat out Pulp Fiction and Shawshank for best.
Now
picture.
Shawshank, you could make.
Yeah, I think Shawshank's a better movie.
Shawshank
I think
is
Pulp
an,
Fiction's a better movie.
I don't know that. I don't know that. The other thing too about that, Roger, the soundtrack from Forrest Gump is outstanding.
Yeah,
Just I don't know if you looked at the
any
soundtrack.
Vietnam
it's got
War era of
40. Yeah, 40.
Oh, the soundtrack's awesome. I'm talking about the movie.
Yeah, I think the fact that Tom Hanks created that character, and there's the Godfather again.
Anytime this music comes up, Justin morphs into Luca Brasi.
Randy Rainwater's listening, and he says it was Lyndon Johnson, not JFK, in the Forrest Gump. Am I wrong on that?
I thought
it was Lyndon B. Johnson.
Are we sure? Do we want to make a bet on that double R?
All right, I'm looking.
I think it was Kennedy.
Damn right.
Because you repeat. I think it was somebody else.
I thought it was Kennedy.
So because he drank a
it's
lot
better.
Of Dr. Pepper.
Yeah, it's better.
I think it's Kennedy.
Let's see.
It's Lyndon Johnson.
All right, double R. Wow. Double R. You're the winner. I knew.
Johnson's in that
was
movie.
Was right.
Kennedy's
always.
And Nixon.
Damn.
Kennedy did something.
I thought Kennedy was in the movie, too. I may be
wrong.
There's
one with him and Nixon also.
Oh, he said this to turn the tape off or something. What did he say? By the way, too, as you're looking for that, Melinda Mayo sent me a text a second ago and said, "Don't forget tonight on Channel 7, the 30th anniversary special for the Hogs 1994 National Championship Dream Season will include Nolan, Scotty Thurman, and others."
I saw that, yeah.
Yeah, 30 years, man. 30 years. Holy mackerel.
Yeah, he's with JFK too.
So what does he do with JFK? That's what I thought he did. I don't remember that. Which one does he say I got to go pee?
Let's see.
Double R, but Double R was right. Listen, I didn't know he had Lyndon Johnson in there too. What would he have done with the difference between Lyndon Johnson and JFK? This is when Acri starts screaming. If he knows all the answers.
You're right. JFK told he had to go pee.
Boom. All right, so I got that part of it right. And then, but Double R.
See, there were Johnson.
What was you doing? Oh,
you know why he got shot in the buttocks? No, that's the same one, isn't it? Which one did he get shot in the buttocks?
So he gets a medal from LBJ, and he gets a plaque, I think, from Nixon. And then.
Well, the LBJ. What is this?
Oh, he's an All-American, I think. So that's why he gets to meet.
LBJ?
No, JFK.
Okay.
LBJ.
Yeah, LBJ would have been while he was in the military.
Military, and then I don't know why he gets to meet Nixon.
Yeah.
Well, Nixon, I know he won a.
He called him on the Watergate
championship at Alabama.
Yeah, that's for JFK.
Yeah, he called. He called somebody about Watergate. Saw some lights on across the street, and that would have been Nixon. But I don't remember the Nixon scene.
He meets Nixon because he was on the ping pong team.
That's what it was. Okay. He was national team.
On the ping pong
team. And that's why he was in Washington, and that's when he saw the. Okay, very good.
So listen to this too, Jennifer Maughan, who we had on the show with Heather. If you remember, I don't know if Justin, you were on the show with us. Jennifer Maughan won the national cooking competition, the national cooking show, Roger.
Yeah.
And now her career is taking off, doing all the national stuff.
Yeah.
She just sent a text. She goes, "Okay, I missed the first part of the conversation, but Luca Brasi." From Godfather is my husband's fourth cousin. His family's Italian and from New York.
Oh, wow.
He was a hitman in real life. How crazy is that? That's you're related to Luca Brasi. What was his real name? We'll have to get his we'll take a break and come back and get his real name, but he definitely, I was thinking, man, if they casted that character, they casted somebody that nailed the look and nailed the sound. But that's great, Jennifer. Thanks for sending us that text. All right, it's 9:30 here on Morning Mayhem. A little jam right there by Master RS.
Oh, come on. Come on.
It's my favorite thing.
You know what? I want to get some walk-up music at trivia.
Here's one in on our text line. Says, my grandson is one of the catchers, part of the battery, at ASU Three Rivers. It's their first year to have a baseball team.
Awesome.
Did you know that, Justin? This is their first year having a baseball team?
I did not. No.
I think Justin may need to go out there and show him a few things. Put a little clinic for the right price, I guess.
I don't think they need my help.
All right, 9:30 here, Morning Mayhem.
Listen every Wednesday when RJ Hawk joins his old buddies on Morning Mayhem. Presented by Natural State Wholesale Flooring. See everything that Natural State Wholesale has to offer at naturalstatewholesale.com.
This is SportsCenter.
Arkansas Razorbacks baseball cruised to an 11-0 win yesterday over in-state rival Little Rock. Ben Bibee, Dylan Carter, Christian Fouch, and Stone Hewitt combined to throw 7 innings of shutout baseball. Bibee struck out 5 of the 10 batters that he faced. And on the day, Vahiva Aloy, the shortstop for the Hogs, drove in 4 runs as well. The Hogs are now 20-3 overall. They host number 8 LSU this weekend in a Thursday, Friday, Saturday series. First game is 6 p.m. on Thursday. Second game is 7 o'clock on Friday. The series finale is at 2 p.m. on Saturday afternoon. Arkansas softball had their game against UCA canceled due to cold temperatures. I'm Josh Neighbors for the Buzz Radio Network.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Another sunny but cool day with a high of just 62 to yesterday, though, and tonight's low will drop back down to about 39. A little warmer tomorrow at 68 and low 70s back by Friday. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Tune in to Out of Bounds each Monday for Weekend Recap, brought to you by Fleet Management Services. Serving Central Arkansas for over 20 years, they're your small to mid-sized fleet specialists, offering diagnostic, suspension, tires, maintenance, engine, transmission repair, and much more. When you need someone to service your fleet and get your employees back on the road quick, call 501-375-3672. Conveniently located at 901 East 8th Street in downtown Little Rock.
Roger, what's the matter?
I'm trying to figure out the best time for me to get down to Oakland. I may not be able to make it down for the rest of the year.
You have until May 5th, number one. Number two, you've got the Oakland Anywhere app. It's that easy. You don't have to be there to bet.
Oh, my gosh. Well, tell everybody, because I already know how they can do that.
Well, the great thing, too, Roger, even this weekend at the Arkansas Derby with 50, 60,000 people there, and you being in the infield, you don't have to go to a teller window. You just use the Oakland Anywhere app.
And that's on my iPhone or my iPad user, Android, too?
That's exactly right. And if you're a new member, you sign up, you get a $150 sign-up bonus by using the promo code BUZZ24, B-U-Z-Z-24.
Watch and wager in horse racing on any track from any smartphone, tablet, or personal computer. Earn points for cash back for every dollar wagered.
iPhone and iPad users, search for the app and download from the App Store. Android users, go to bet.oakline.com and save to your home screen. And don't forget, it is the Arkansas Derby this Saturday, March 30th. Don't miss it. First post time, 12 o'clock noon. Doors open at 10:30. It's here.
It's there.
It's Oakland Anywhere.
Clayton Homes of Conway is moving. But until then, you can find them at their location on East Dave Ward Drive, where you're invited to stop by on April 12th and 13th for their inventory reduction sale. Save thousands of dollars on in-stock inventory of homes. Lenders will be available for all your financing questions. There'll be door prizes, food, fun, and entertainment for the whole family. April 12th and 13th at Clayton Homes at Conway.
Old Man Winter here. One more snowstorm.
Not a chance, Mr. Winter. It's spring.
It's also time for the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event, where you can get great deals on all our award-winning Hyundai models, all backed by America's best warranty. Hurry in. These deals won't last at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Now get 0% APR on the Tucson or pay only $369 a month with zero down payment. Now, during the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Offers end soon. Call 469-613-0227 for details.
Hennard Foothills Equipment in Searcy, one of Arkansas's leaders in hay equipment. They handle a full line of Kubota tractors and hay tools, as well as Vermeer hay products. 501-268-1987. Hennard Foothills Equipment in Searcy, your hometown dealer, no matter where you live.
Through the end of March, the deals could not be hotter at Arch Marine in North Little Rock. Ready for this? The ever-so-popular G3 boats with rebates up to $3,000 off already discounted 2022 and 23 models. The deals are hot, hot, hot at Arch Marine in North Little Rock. Come see us.
This is Miss Arkansas Corey Keller, and you're listening to Morning Mayhem on 103.7 The Bus.
Well, sometimes you have to go all out when you're the king, and you can't help it, you know? Because there's only one man who's a king. God picks him, hand plucks him. One night, God looked down at all the millions and millions and millions of people, man. And he decided which one was the best. It was me. And he plucked me from all those millions and millions and millions of people, man.
Yeah?
Listen to this right now. There's two things you need to know.
Uh-huh.
I'm the king. And number two is, look out, man! Look at that, they're coming at you. You see that? It's called karate, man. And only two kinds of people know it. The Chinese and the king. One of them is me.
You're the king.
Oh, see, on the Memphis, they want a nice little bit of honey and a little bit of June bug.
Yeah?
Yeah, oh, yeah. I don't want somewhere around.
Uh-huh.
Oh, come on, man. Oh, come on. See, you're there now. Turn around. See, look out, man. Okay, there's some long game, sir, man.
Hey, I'm telling you right at him. Good. He is looking at him and cannot figure out what in the world.
That so now that is a great movie.
Somebody says here on our text line, JM is an idiot. Gump is iconic. There you go.
Wow.
Wow. Someone says,
well, I'm not an idiot, but okay.
Someone says that
I thought it was a good movie. I just don't think it's as great as everybody thinks.
I'm with
it
you.
Is.
Yeah,
I'm
well, you, Josh is in your corner there.
I'm sorry I broke up your Black Panther party.
That part's weak. See, here's the thing. There's a couple moments where you're like, this is just ridiculous. It's a bit too ridiculous.
Well, it's the whole premise is
why?
Ridiculous.
Because he received the Congressional Medal of Honor.
It's like, I understand.
By the way,
running.
My wife totally disagrees with me. She thinks it's like the greatest movie ever, and I'm like,
well, they did win the Oscar. It
all right, here you go.
Shape of Water won the Oscar.
If they get awards, they're great.
No, but usually it's indicative of a good movie.
Shape of Water won the Oscar. Did you like the Alien?
Well, not everyone's
Shape of Water. All right, here he goes, right here.
I was running. Mom always said life. It's like a box of chocolates.
Yeah.
You never know what you're going to get.
You never know what you're going to get. Hey.
By the way.
Not my Jenny.
No. Jennifer Mon, who told us that she's related to Luca Brasi, is said the guy's real name is Lenny Montana. He was an ex-wrestler and former bodyguard and enforcer for the Colombo crime family.
Lenny Montana. Hey, what are you kidding me here? His name is not Luca Brasi. It's Lenny Montana.
You guys know what Luca Brasi does? He sleeps with the fishes.
He sleeps with the fishes. He does.
Watch your little pirate
also
mouth.
Apparently Nixon told Forrest Gump he needs to stay at the Watergate Hotel. I don't remember that in the movie, but
that's why I saw it across the street.
I wanted to read this message from one of our listeners who sent sent this early this morning. You guys on the bus for the morning show to drive time really fill the gap when there's no sports going on here in Radio Land. We really want to thank you for bringing it every day, putting up with fans, good or bad at times. Still makes a great show. Really love the buzz. It's the best. Just wish our football and basketball team was as good as the buzz.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so we appreciate that. Hey, listen, the baseball.
I love it. Yeah. I just got told I suck.
How about that? How about that? In the same breath.
Arkansas did beat the Trojans yesterday, 11-0, 7 innings. 2-hit shutout by the pitching staff. Our man Peyton Stovall hit another home run. I think it's his third. It was 11-0, and obviously Chris Curry said what an amazing staff this team has, pitching staff for sure. So LSU starts Thursday night. I like the Thursday, Friday, Saturday as opposed to Friday, Saturday, Sunday. I don't know why. I guess because we get another game in during the weekday, but it'll be rocking at Baum Stadium with LSU coming to town. So and I think we're out of tickets for that, right, Josh? No more tickets for that?
Yep, we're out.
We're done. And then softball, no
more. I don't like it because of my schedule.
Well, I know. Well, I thought that would help.
Home and seeing a game on
Sunday.
Oh,
you get Sunday. Yeah, you get the Sunday game. Yeah. But you do get the Thursday game. You get to see the Thursday game, don't you? So you get Thursday, Friday? You get Thursday, Friday.
Depending on the time.
Yeah.
I do.
Yeah, and also, too, we mentioned earlier, Roger, did you buy a ticket last night for the Mega Millions at 1.1?
I did not buy one.
Brian Morse kept telling me, he said, David, you need to go buy a ticket.
Well, the Boudreaux's crew on Tuesdays, is that the Powerball's Tuesday night? Brian will always come up to us on Tuesday when they're huge, and he will remind everybody, hey, you want to go in and get some tickets at Boudreaux? So he will do that a lot.
I have a question. Would you all stop working if you all won?
If we had $1 billion, probably so.
No,
I don't think you would.
My position here would change.
A billion or a million?
A billion.
My position, yeah, it's
yeah.
True.
My position here at the office would change.
Y'all will never see me again.
All right, I want to ask you all. So Baz says he would. Do you all think Roger and JM? Do you guys think Baz would? I don't. I don't think Baz would stop working.
He wouldn't stop. No. Because his position at this office would change too.
You know what? Would we? I'd share it with y'all.
I know you would.
How much should I share with you?
Well, for me, since you're
how much should I share?
Half a billion.
Obviously, I'm going to get I'll get the lion's share of who you give your buddies to. Now, your mom and your dad are going to get that. You're going to get all
what
that.
What do you think I should give Roger, Justin, if I win $1 billion?
Well, don't put Justin on that spot.
Half.
Thank you, Justin.
How much do you need, Roger? How much do you need?
I don't know yet. I don't know.
Would $1 million be enough?
He needs half.
Would $1 million be enough?
Would $1 million if I get
$1 million? $1 million wouldn't be enough because here's the, I want to keep $1 million in there at all times. $1 million wouldn't be enough. At least.
Good Lord.
Oh, good. You just got $1 billion, you selfish son of a bitch.
At least $100 million.
No, after.
Million.
Yeah, yeah. How much?
At least $100 million.
But here's what I do, though.
That's 1/10.
Thank you, Justin.
Listen to you.
It's the trickle down. What I would do with the. I'm not keeping it all. I set up a foundation. I start a foundation. I do. I start a foundation for them. I start my own social network.
He finally gets that pull.
Yes, he does. He does.
Well, no.
Sam.
No.
If you get $1 million, are you getting the pool?
Yes.
No.
He's not. If not $1 million, he's not getting the pool.
Not getting the pool.
Listen, they're going to still have to come in there and cut down that tree.
Hey, we got to say congratulations. If you missed it early in the show, Steve Rook, the chancellor of Arkansas State University Three Rivers, called to announce that the university is giving, the college rather, is giving Justin Moore an honorary degree. So that's very exciting.
That's outstanding.
Very exciting.
So what do you, listen,
you and Double R the same year.
They have really,
really, really.
Oh, stop it. Like listen, you're one of the cats that deserve these things like that.
You might inspire somebody. So you went to school for just a short moment in time.
You have just raised the IQ on this show.
That's right. And May 14th is going to be the graduation.
May 14th.
We're going to be there.
May 14th, that's a Tuesday, right? Is that what he said?
I need to look at that date real quick.
Yeah. Tuesday is what he said. May 14th. Yep.
Let's see if we
now a week before
that. Let's see if we have a remote that day, May 14th.
Will you be there?
We're clear. We're good. May 14th, we're good for that. So we're all going to be there. You know what? We're doing the show live from there that day.
Here's the deal.
From the classroom that Justin attended one time.
That is Boudreaux's trivia night. Is that right? Tuesday?
Yes.
I will go to graduation. I will forego Boudreaux to go to this graduation.
I'm thinking it's a daytime of graduation.
Oh, I don't know.
I don't know. It's a Tuesday.
Here's the deal. I made my statement before knowing that.
Josh, when you graduated, was it a daytime? I think most of it was daytime.
Mine was noon. I remember I was watching a college basketball game on my phone.
Justin's going to be the only guy that takes his honorary degree and turns it into a doctorate.
You do have to put a tassel on one of your hats, though.
Move it over.
And
you got to toss it.
Done.
Absolutely. We all wear hats that day.
Yeah, I really regret if I could go back in time, I'd tell 22-year-old Basil, get your butt back up there and walk.
You didn't walk?
I didn't walk, yeah.
Why not?
I just was ready to get out of town, ready to get back.
He already had something planned. He was already doing something.
Let me tell you, my last class, no joke, I had my car packed, my Mazda RX-7 black, tinted windows black. I walked out of that last class. It was a wooden pencil. Snap that thing, baby. Hit the road, headed south, right that same day.
Did you think you'd be back in Arkansas?
Yeah, I did. But that day, I was done with school.
There's some DNA testing still going on.
Shut it. All right, Justin, I know you got to jump off, buddy.
We're going to miss you, bud.
Maybe we'll talk to you maybe Friday. Is that right? Maybe Friday?
Not tomorrow?
Friday.
Maybe, yeah. So normally
he would, Friday?
He has a conflict with
you have a conflict? We're going to be with Frank Friday, so Frank will love having you.
That's right. So hopefully we'll talk to you on Friday then, buddy. Congratulations on the degree. Very nice.
Congratulations, your bub.
Well done.
Thanks, guys.
All right. 9:45, we'll be back and wrap things up.
Hey, Wilson, where are you heading?
Man, I'm going to see Matt Jones.
I love Matt Jones. You got Miracle on Markham.
Matt Jones, the real Matt Jones, Raj.
The real Matt Jones? Oh, you mean the mortgage expert Matt Jones at Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union in Benton.
That's the one.
Did you know that Matt Jones at Alcoa Community FCU is a Benton boy and a graduate of OBU? So he's very familiar with Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry Counties.
Yep.
Did you know that in addition to being a mortgage lender expert, Matt Jones is also a licensed realtor who can give you insight into both sides of your mortgage transaction?
I did.
So go see Matt Jones at Alcoa Community FCU for all your mortgage needs. And if you're looking at buying a new home or need to refinance the home you're already in, the real Matt Jones at Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union is your guy. Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, serving all of Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry Counties. For more information or to apply securely online, go to alcoacommunityfcu.org. And remember, with the real Matt Jones, miracles can still happen.
Quality Outdoor Products in Alexander, your metal roofing superstore, has a brand new showroom. Take exit 126 off I-30 and visit with Cal about a new carport or metal building. 40-year colors are available at only $2.89 a foot. 20-year colors are $2.59 and Galvalume runs $2.49. Trim and accessories are always available. Take exit 126 in Alexander or call Cal at 501-455-0240 about a new carport, metal building, or metal roofing supplies.
Hey, it's Craig O'Neill, and I got a question for you. Did you know that Pettijean Meats has been providing the best quality smoked meat for over 95 years? Pettijean Meats is fourth generation. It's Arkansas-owned and operated by the same family, continuing the tradition. You can start a tradition. Pettijean smoked ham for Easter, smoked over real hickory wood. Oh, go whole ham this Easter. Always ask for, no demand. Pettijean Meats. Taste the difference.
Hello, folks. It's Frank Fletcher from the Fletcher Dodge store here in Sherwood. For the past few months, we've been asking you to give us a chance to buy your cars, and the response has been great. We really appreciate all of you who brought your cars in and turned it into cash. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Folks, we're still buying cars every day. So look around and see what you or your family has in the garage that you want to turn into cash. It's really easy, folks. Just come into Fletcher Dodge and ask for Chris or Andy. We'll buy any vehicle and we'll pay you more than anyone. We can't find enough vehicles at the auto auctions to meet the demand, so we're extending you this offer to the public. We'll pay you more, so don't wait. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Come see us today for the best cash offer on your car, truck, van, or SUV. Just ask for Chris or Andy. We'll pay you more, so come see us at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood. Thanks.
Spring means it's time for fresh vegetables and produce. And your local Family Market store is your home for everything spring, including all of those barbecue supplies and fresh cut meats by our butchers for your spring cookouts. With great deals on all of your favorite Coke, Pepsi, and Frito-Lay items, as well as so much more, Family Market in Pangburn, Malvern, and Shannon Hills are always there for you. And remember, you'll never pay full price for gas when you use your Family Market rewards card at select locations. Family Market, the way grocery shopping is supposed to be.
It's Kubota Orange Days. Shop the year's best selection of Kubota tractors, zero-turn mowers, and utility vehicles, including the number one selling compact tractor in the USA. And now, through June 30th, get 0% APR for 84 months and up to $2,500 off BX23S tractors. See the details at KubotaOrangeDays.com.
When you get on a bike, you gotta watch out for gravel, potholes, and knucklehead drivers.
But after a crash, here's what you gotta watch out for. Insurance adjusters. They can be tough on injured bikers.
They might try to pin the blame on you or pay you less than you deserve.
So if you've been injured, here's what you should do.
Call the lawyers who look out for bikers. That's Rainwater, Holt, and Sexton. Motorcycle crash? Call Rainwater, Holt, and Sexton. Anywhere in the state, dial 888-8888.
Non-lawyer spokesperson. Responsible attorneys Michael Rainwater and Bob Sexton.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? I'm Wes Moore. Coming up Wednesday on Out of Bounds, Kendall Diggs will join us. Thanks to Stephen Elmore, Shelter Insurance. We'll get his thoughts on the game against the Little Rock Trojans, the Auburn series, and look ahead to the LSU Tigers. Top 10 matchup at Baum Walker Stadium this weekend. Also coming up, we'll talk about the NCAA tournament. Pat Bradley will join us. We'll get his thoughts on the Sweet 16. All that and a whole lot more coming up Wednesday on Out of Bounds.
This is Quinn Grovey, and you're listening to Morning Mayhem on 103.7 The Buzz.
Oh, my gosh, that's good stuff.
College grad.
That is good stuff. Hell, how about that? Double R and Justin Moore together getting honorary degrees. I'd say that's outstanding. I think, listen, too, I think there's some more good things coming for Justin in the coming months. I'll say more about that later, but... Anyway, tomorrow, Roger, we'll be on the road at Triple C.
Looking forward to that. It's the Gravely Tour. It starts up this year. I love this time
of year.
Did
you hear Roger's songs? Yes.
Oh, I know, and I hadn't written a new one yet, and I'm talking to Brian Morris last night. You know what he told me?
What's that?
No. He said, don't do it.
We'll have Hannah Gammel on tomorrow, and Tommy will be checking in with us by phone, and we'll hear from Joe Klein tomorrow. And then Friday we'll be with Frank Fletcher at Fletcher Dodge, Chrysler Jeep Ram, their end of the month sale. But a lot of talk about the Arkansas Derby. So, you know, obviously that's a big – now, last year, remember, Frank had – was it Rocket – which is it Rocket Can, the one that really hoped he
Rocket
could do –
Rocket Can was in the Derby?
Rocket Can.
Yeah.
Was it the Arkansas Derby?
Yeah, remember. Yeah.
We just had Rocket Can.
I didn't know that's how it worked.
Does Frank have one this year or no?
No, he does not have one. But
I did not know that that's how it worked. I thought after the Derby, you're not going to be on any other race.
I do want to give a shout-out to Daniel Robinson over at Simmons Bank.
Hey, Dan.
Roger, I had to sign some documents yesterday. And I'll tell you, we started talking about things, and he pretty much was just telling me things that we had said on this show. And so just got to appreciate clients that we have that are sponsors on the show that also listen every day and listen to all the things. Listen, I finally just said, well, you should just come on and do a segment, have your own segment. So anyway, so thank you, Daniel. You talk about a Locked In Hog fan, too. You know, sometimes we forget
locked on.
So anyway, also remember Arkansas Derby is Saturday. The infield is open on Friday and the infield is open on Saturday. So It is going to, the weather apparently is supposed to be amazing. We'll be at the Mainline Sports Bar
Thursday night.
Thursday night too. Yeah, so we'll come out there and hang out. We had a record crowd last week, and I'm sure we'll have it again this weekend. It
Thanks
was huge.
A lot, Steve Qualls, for everything that he does. Listen, we got a picture of Hannah Gamble.
Yeah, with her morning mayhem. Yes.
We got a picture of Caleb Battle. I got those. Yeah. I've got some other pictures.
Gotta get him
a
Stovall. Gotta get him a Will McIntyre. Craig's got his shirt.
Craig's got his shirt. Vickery's got his. I've asked Vickery to take a picture right away. He said he was gonna go Costanza.
Yes.
And you know the Costanza look. He's on a couch and he's doing the lion. I said, but Bill, Costanza doesn't have a shirt on. He said, well, that'll be all I'm wearing. So we're looking to get Bill on that one. We'll get Craig to do one as well. So that'll be cool.
Justin Anchorage joins us. Good morning, Justin.
Hey,
how
fellas.
Are you? What's going on, man?
What's up?
It's all about you. How are you?
Great.
Yes. What's your plans for the weekend?
I'm going to do the show Friday at Oaklawn, and then we're going to stick around with the races. My son's going to be with me. And then
Friday, the races, and then,
so the office is closed, but we're on.
We're working.
Yeah.
Dig it. Okay.
Yeah. And then Friday night, we'll go out to dinner in Hot Springs somewhere. And then Saturday, I'm doing Oaklawn Race Day. And then we will be at the races all day on Saturday.
Cool.
And then we're coming back Saturday night because Easter's on Sunday, which is difficult to turn around. So there you go.
Where are you going to be hanging at on Derby Day? All over? And are you going to have like a home base?
No. I'll float. We'll go to the Tito's tent for a little bit.
So I saw Mac
yesterday.
Assuming
Mac will. Yeah. I saw that. You guys, massaging clients, also known as day drinking. But anyway, yeah. So I will stop in the Tito's tent, and then we'll sit along the finish line. Typically, is where I like to be. You can see the races the best up there. I love being in the tent. It's a great experience, and I'm always thankful to get the opportunity.
It's
hard to watch the races from down there. So if you're there for the party, that's it.
Yeah.
But if you're there to really watch the races, it's tough. Yeah.
And the Sigma tent, we've got the
that's on the far north
and
end,
you've got the screen. There's a screen over there, but you're not in the infield to watch it.
But the weather's so perfect.
Yeah, oh my
you
gosh,
can't go wrong.
Do you remember it was what 3 years ago, 4 years ago when it would just pour and rain? It would just ruins everything.
And I've been there when it last year was perfect.
Oh, it was perfect last year.
That was the day after the tornado.
That's right.
It was.
We talked about that a few times. Hard to believe.
And we've been there several times when we walked through, and it's been like mud and all that straw. I feel like I'm one of the slaves in Egypt making bricks.
This weekend is going to be spectacular. So what's happening on the show today?
Well, we don't do a lot of this. This is not our lead story, but I just was thinking about this because we're going to the Grizzlies game tonight. But we're going to go. We're talking about the standings in the NBA. I don't know if you guys saw the Lakers game last night. It was pretty wild. Austin Reeves had a huge game, second triple-double of his career. So we're going to talk about that a little bit, just kind of where everybody is for the few that do like the NBA.
Right.
Main story, of course, going to be baseball. We'll talk about the shutout yesterday. Hagan Smith's on with us today, actually, so it's good timing at 10:30. And just another arm for Arkansas. We knew Bobby was going to be good when he got in there, and he was great yesterday. So he's brought to you by Stifel Financial. Joe Klein's in the studio, at least last I heard. Kevin Kelly's in, thanks to the Little Rock Athletic Club. We had a chance to go over and check out their new pickleball.
Yeah, how is it?
It is so cool, and they have such a great setup in there. They did such a great job on that facility, and it's not super convenient for me now back downtown, but thinking about joining the club just so I could have access to the indoor pickleball. It's so cool.
That's exciting.
Michael Felder at 11:30. We'll talk about what's going on with college football and get his thoughts on some of these quarterbacks. There's been a lot of debate about who's the guy. J.J. McCarthy, you know, Harbaugh says he's the best quarterback in the draft. Well,
whoa!
A lot of people are starting to kind of gain steam on that, but, you know, many people are going to ride Caleb Williams, and I think the Bears are going to, too. And then everybody else has talked to him, so we're finally getting everybody's leftovers. Neil Erzman's going to join us in studio. I feel kind of lame because everybody else already had him on, but we're going to get him in.
You get him in studio.
I tried to get him Monday, but he was tied up. So
I was going to ask, what do you think about the new NFL kickoff rule?
Change is always hard, right?
Yeah.
I have to see it
I've seen it. I've seen video of it. I've seen XFL video. The first time I saw it yesterday.
I'll have to see it through a season and see if we like it or not. They're doing it. You know, DJ, his biggest complaint is he doesn't like the fair catch in the field of play. So that's going away, at least. So if you like that part of it, it's fine. I mean, kicking in the end zone, giving it to him at the 30 for NFL offense is too much of an advantage, right?
Yeah.
So you're going to think you'd be really good at not kicking
it
in the end zone.
So if it drops in the red zone, it's as good as being in the end zone, if it drops in the red zone?
If it's in the field of play?
Yeah.
No, you still have to return it.
So, I thought so, too.
The only disadvantage if you're the defender, if you're on the kickoff team, again, for those that don't know, you've gone on the other side where the receiving team is on the 40. So you're standing there
flat. The coverage unit is on the 40.
Unit. So you're standing there flat-footed waiting for this guy running at you. He's going to have a 20-yard running advantage.
No. You can't move. Until the ball is fielded.
That's what I'm saying. So I'm standing flat-footed until he catches it.
Yeah.
Then he takes off, and I'm still having to, at that point, I'm trying to get rid of the blocker because the blocker's right on me. So I'm standing. So he's got a pretty good head of steam coming at me.
He's only got 5 yards.
Huh?
He's only got 5 yards.
What's that?
The blocker.
That's what I'm saying. But the
cover, the protection unit is 30 between the 30 and 35.
Yes.
They're lining up at the 40, so they only have a 5-yard window there.
I'm talking about the return guy. He's going to have about a 20-yard hit running. Yes.
Yes.
So
that's true.
So I'm flat footed. This guy's got a 20-yard.
Oh, you're talking about as a tackler.
Yes, as a tackler. So
I thought you were saying that it was a disadvantage for the blockers.
No. I'm saying so you've got to be able to get off your block, and that guy's running full speed.
Yeah,
so
they're trying to create. Making that play important, yeah, maybe you're right. Yeah, they're onto something there.
As an old defender, that's like, wow, man, he's got momentum. He's got speed coming at me, so I better not be able to have to tackle him by myself.
I guess
most
the punt
the
return's perfect. They're not worried about that.
No, yeah, I guess so. So we'll see. I'm open to that. Yeah. So, all right, Roger, we will be on the road tomorrow up in Conway.
Triple C, Gravely Tour begins. A big, big, big special. The Mow the Distance sale starts again for the first time in years.